farted on the candles and blown them out. All right. Hey, listen, I got to move along because Insane Clown Posse's here.
Can I plug my column?
All right, go ahead, honey.
It's on worldnetdaily.com and townhall.com. And Howard, there's new pictures of me. So.
Nude?
No, new.
Oh, no. All right. I'll check those out. Come back when they're nude. Goodbye. All right, listen, Insane Clown Posse is here. Violent J and Shaggy 2 Dope.
They're both here.
Yeah, two of my favorite guests.
They're not in jail.
They've got something to say. I don't know what it is, but they always have something fun to say.
Well, every time I've read about them lately, they've been either being arrested or in court or something.
Yeah, and then they got dumped by their record label, too.
You're kidding.
I think so, yeah. Got to ask them about it. They're releasing some sort of single for Halloween, which is a very new move for them. They've never done this before.
No holiday.
They're
song.
The boys, and look at the beautiful makeup. They look good. They look fresh. A couple of new tattoos. Shaggy 2 Dope got his neck tattooed.
Look at this. Look
That's
at
new.
Maybe.
That's new, right?
My new.
New hair.
Less than a year old.
New hairdos.
About a year growth. Yeah.
Today.
Sorry, Violent J, what's that?
Who do you got for us to battle today?
There'll be someone,
think
I'm
you're
sure.
Prepared.
Violent
you sound
J,
a little tired.
You look great, but I think you put on some weight. You look,
that's right.
You did.
It's a symbol of my wealth.
What's going on? Even
he's
vocally.
Part Polynesian, you know, like it's a symbol of being rich.
You sound
or is he going into sugar?
You sound sick.
I feel great.
Yeah, what's the matter? Are you sick?
We've been torn.
You got anthrax?
Yeah, I mean, really, I'm worried about you.
I think
you.
We got anthrax floating on our bus.
Right, I don't doubt it.
No, we've been torn, and my mental is breaking down, you know what I mean?
Right, right. I've never seen you like this.
Seriously falling apart.
Are you doing a Mariah Carey? You can't take the pressure?
Hey, Mariah Carey does it for publicity stunts. When I get locked up in the St. Asylums, nobody reads about it. You know
what's
what
going
mean?
On? Seriously, you put on a bunch of weight since I last saw you. You got bigger. You did.
Yeah.
Are you nervous? Or are you?
No, what it is
steroids, man. Steroids.
First of all, not all of this is fat, it's solid. You know what I'm saying?
You're not weak from.
No. Pick up something, break it.
Is it beer or are you drinking maybe a lot?
No, I'm drinking a lot of Faygo soda, but that's always been the case. You know
right,
what I mean?
Right, right. I'm worried
fine.
About it.
Fine. It's just that you can't. Okay, put it like this. Let's go back to 1997 when we first came on the show.
Right.
You know, we were the biggest joke. We were the biggest fluke. You know, look at these clowns.
And you're still here.
We're still here.
And what
happened? What's that got to do with how much weight you've gained?
Because I can't deal with it no more. It's like, okay.
And plus, we keep getting more and more pay so you can afford
well, let
the
me
pizza
ask you this,
what? With the extra toppings.
No, the pressure, you understand? The pressure is like, why isn't anybody coming back and saying, damn, you know what? They were right.
Right.
It's making me go.
You're upset about not getting recognition?
Well, Sharon Osbourne, the wife of Ozzy Osbourne, was here.
Let's talk about that. Bitch for a minute.
Okay.
The money she owes me.
All right. And she said that you guys would get dropped by a record company and you said.
Happened.
No.
She dropped.
She didn't get dropped by nothing.
She told me you were dropped by a record company.
Come on. So
that's what she told you.
Right.
Yeah, of
it's
course.
Not true?
Listen.
Are people
Let's
hoping
rewind the film. Let's
right.
rewind the footage, whatever. Last time we were on the show, she bet us $50,000 our new album, Bizarre, Bizarre, wouldn't sell 50,000 copies.
Right.
Well, to date, each record has sold 250,000 copies.
Where's my money?
I want my money.
Right.
And I want it donated to the Red Cross in the name of Insane Clown Posse. And I know that bitch can afford it. All she has to do is drain it out of that heroin addict husband of hers and come up with the damn money. You know what I mean?
Right, I hear you.
I'm calling her out on national TV, only she's over in London, or excuse me,
Italy, crumpet.
No, she's in Wales
yeah.
or whatever. But she needs to come over here and put that damn money that she fronted.
And yo,
she said she made a bet. She lost a bet.
She ought to
the
pay.
Bitch needs
yeah.
to come up with the money
right.
and put
and
it in our name
pounds.
To the Red Cross.
She lost a tremendous amount
That's right.
of money.
And we ain't accepting pounds.
She lost it. You're right. She's
losing pounds. Yeah. Whatever. Who cares?
But
she's nasty as hell.
But Violent J put on as much weight as she took off.
He took her weight off.
Somewhere,
I'm a
right?
guy, though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You guys wouldn't believe this.
You're still handsome.
But chicks like big teddy bear guys.
Are you guys getting laid now? Because last time I spoke to you, you weren't. Are you saying you're getting laid more because you're a heavier
See,
set?
That's what makes it hard to lose weight because I'm not getting any less chicks.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. If
I was getting less chicks and chicks were like, I'm not going to have sex with you because you're so fat now, then I'd be like, well, I got to do something about it.
But when you take your clothes off and stuff, do you ever feel insecure that, like, you don't look your best?
I haven't took my shirt off with the exception of being arrested
right.
and being forced to since I was about 9 years old.
You don't take your shirt off.
But let me tell you something. With a chick, what do? You just get serviced orally? I mean,
I turn the lights off.
You do?
And
I've known this guy since I was about 10 years old, about 17 years. I've never seen him without a shirt on.
I'm talking about before I was fat. This is when, you know,
swimming pools, everything.
Really? If you go swimming?
Always fully dressed.
If you go swimming, you wear a shirt?
All the time.
Really?
And I'll tell you what.
Shower.
It's a little bit of an emotional story, but short. When my mom used to date this guy, and one day he came home drunk, and it was like 110 degrees, you know what I mean? I'm upstairs sleeping. I guess I tossed and tangled out of my clothes. I was naked. Well, he comes in the bedroom.
He tried to rape you?
And no, he's beating my ass over something, you know?
Really?
And all I'm trying to do is put my underoos back on.
Right.
So now I can't be naked. I always got to be ready to jump. You
mean your parents divorced when you were young?
Man, yeah. I had a whole bunch of dads, you know?
You had a bunch of dads.
Yeah.
And they used to come in the room when you were naked and beat you?
Just one guy. Boyfriend of hers. He had the radio up real loud. And he told me not to tell my mom, and I told my mom. And he came in the house that night.
You think he was getting off on you? Because you are an attractive man. I mean,
I was like, 10 years old.
Why would he beat your ass, though? What did you do wrong?
He was drunk. My mom can't pull the best looking guys. You know what I'm saying?
What are you saying?
Right.
The greatest guy.
I mean,
is your mom not hot?
My mom's hot as hell, man.
Right.
But she can't pull the good
guys? No, I'm asking. You're saying she can't get good guys. I'm saying maybe.
My mom is the bomb. Let's drop.
You do love you. You love your mother.
You were the one who said, "My mom can't pull the greatest."
Yeah, I'm not.
No, he said greatest.
My mom has been to hell and back many, many, many times. You understand?
So when you said she can't pull in the greatest looking guys, I assumed that maybe she wasn't that hot, is what you said.
Okay. When I walked in the room, everybody's still. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Well, picture the stress I've been through. And triple that by 50 times. And
now next time
she's going to
be twice as big.
So you're saying she was done in by the stress.
That's right. And that will do in people. But I'm not stressed and I'm happy.
You had an unhappy childhood. Because I see you getting emotional when you talk about your mom and all the different fathers you
have. Well, it's all up front because I'm writing a book right now. So
How many dads?
All on the surface.
It
you
is.
Know what I mean?
How many dads would you say you had?
That's me on the keys, too.
Sharon Osbourne won't pay me my money.
A very special violent
And we don't accept crumpets, Sharon.
Yeah, we don't accept pence. Give us the damn American dollars.
Are you one of those guys looking for a dad? I mean, are you always looking for affection and stuff?
Man, I couldn't give a damn about my dad. I know my real dad wishes he knew me now. He'd come and get some of his money we're making.
Oh, your dad, you don't have anything to do with your real dad?
My real dad left.
When did he leave?
2 years old.
Wow.
And check this out.
And he never came to visit Violent J?
No, listen. See, there's a thing. You wouldn't believe anybody could hold a memory when they were 2 years old.
Right.
But my real father built a haunted house in our basement, and I remembered it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When I was 2 years old. And he also threw a TV at my mom, and I remembered that. So
really?
My brain... is so superior.
Has your dad tried to get in touch with you since you become the huge megastar that you are?
You know what? My uncle called me once, and I should have down real quick. I said, if I ever see my real father, I'm going to have to knock him out.
Really?
Not because he left me and I grew up without a father. That wasn't the problem. My mom was enough fathers for 50 fathers, you know?
Right.
It's because of, things that happened with him on my mind. He took their last paycheck and he took it and ran, you know? And there's things he did that my mom told me as I grew up that caused for an ass whipping, you know what I mean?
Right.
But not that he wasn't there.
Right.
I don't care. I got Shaggy.
Do you ever get curious? Do you ever get curious and, like, want to get a handle on where he is?
Do you know where he is?
He's probably like that chick you just had in here, cracked up lips, smoking the pipe, living somewhere. I don't want to know who that is.
Howard?
Right. Yes? Howard. Oh, Gene Simmons of KISS, boys. Yes, Gene.
Hello, boys. This is Gene Simmons.
Hey, it's an honor to meet you, Gene.
From KISS.
Yeah, I know.
You know that a lot of people try to tell KISS that Insane Clown Posse took a lot of their ideas from KISS, but I disagree. And I'll tell you why. It's a very important announcement I want to make right now that not too many people know about.
Go ahead, shoot.
Violent J, the heavy one on the right. You are my son. This is true. I know that your mother told you that Bozo the Clown was your father, but that's not true.
All right, well, hold on. And if you're my dad, where were we on the opening slot on that Cycle Circus tour that played for 53 million Americans?
Listen, I tried to help you out when you were a kid. You wanted to join the circus. And I said, no, listen to me. You're not going to join the circus.
Right.
You were born with clown makeup on. I'm going to take you to bang Bette Midler. I took you to bang Bette Midler when you were only 4 years old. You don't remember this.
Yes.
But that haunted house in the basement was actually a Kiss concert where we charged $50 to the neighbor.
Well, Gene, you might be my father, but I understand you couldn't raise me. You were having trouble dealing with them trunks in your band like Ace Frehley and them other crackheads you had to pull out of the gutter and slap silly to get them back in shape to do another tour. So I understand
true.
That. You know what I mean?
Neosporin on their crack pipes on their lips and whatnot. You know?
So what about Shaggy Two-Dope? You're so frivolous, you're so light, but did you have also a difficult childhood?
Were you with the kid with the good parents?
Wait a minute. Let me just, before we get into Shaggy, now that Jay's a fat jello bag and he's all messed up.
No, you just gained a little weight, that's all.
I'm the one that's, I look after this guy. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's all I wanted to say. And where's my money from Sharon Osbourne, damn it?
What do you mean you look after Shaggy Two-Dope?
My brother. He's my best friend.
Right.
So neither one of you had family.
He gets drunk. He takes somas. We all do.
Right.
But, you know.
Sleeping sedative.
He goes to jail a lot. I got
a muscle relaxant.
Soma is a muscle relaxant like a 714, like a Quaalude. And where do you boys?
Yeah, you know,
where,
you four or five of them, you know, with like 2 4s of Colt 45.
You seem to know a lot about them.
Tried to escape.
How do you get somas?
It's not your business, man.
I mean, that's what they stopped making, though.
All right, we've been pinching up lately.
Well, could they stop making Quaaludes and somas, I thought.
Oh, somas.
Wait a minute.
You guys do get those.
Well, we, you know, somas, Vicodins.
Well, you boys
get them by the megaton truckload. It's easy on the street.
So you guys addicted to these pills?
A
little bit.
Yeah,
okay,
who cares?
But
don't smoke weed, though.
I mean, you know, I don't shoot heroin in my eyelids or nothing.
You guys do not smoke weed?
No.
H2O is like 16. I don't smoke weed.
Really? You just take legal drugs, prescription drugs.
But they're not buying legal.
Well, I mean, not legal doses, but, you know.
Right. And what do? You need those to sleep because you're under so much pressure from shots?
Nah, I just like getting blew out on them.
Yeah.
Listen, I want to tell you guys something, man. Just one serious thing.
Okay, good.
You were talking about our latest record sold 250,000 copies.
Uh-huh.
There's not a listener out there or anybody in this.
And Insane Clown Posse stopping by. These guys are so popular, there's at least 50 fans downstairs.
You're kidding!
Just fighting to get near them. They're...
I'm shocked!
They are the biggest stars.
Show me these 50 fans.
I swear to God they're down there right now. We got a camera on them. We'll show them on TV.
All right.
When I walked in, there were a lot of ICP supporters. That early, 5:45.
Wow.
Insane Clown Posse's new album, The Wrath, Shangri-La, featuring the single Homies, is available in stores today.
Well, where are they?
Shaggy 2 Dope and Violent J.
Shaggy 2 Dope.
I like Casey hands me a list of who they are, and he's got it completely wrong.
Oh, God.
He goes, Shaggy 2 Dope is the guy with the blonde hair, the big guy, and the skinny little guy is Violent J.
Oh,
he's got
so
it completely
bad.
Wrong. Casey, you give me a note. That's not who these guys are. There you go.
Hey there.
What's the matter with you? He's so funny. Violent J's the guy with the blonde hair. Casey?
You act as if Howard doesn't know?
That's Violent J right there. No, he's not Violent
J.
That's Shaggy 2 Dope.
I'm the friendly one. Friendly 2 Dope.
But he screws me up. Like, he always is supposed to give me the names of whoever's sitting down. Because, you know, sometimes I forget and stuff, but it just so happens I know you guys.
Right.
But you screw me. Why wouldn't you check into it?
Yeah, no, I thought I knew these guys. I thought I knew who it was.
Shaggy 2 Dope is right there.
Never trust your own brain.
The Violent J is right there.
Chilling.
Just chilling.
Horde. Chilling horde.
Chilling horde.
What's the matter? Seriously, man.
You lost weight, though.
Dude, this is like the fifth screw-up this week.
No, it's not. That's the first one.
I don't care if you lost weight. You should still know the guy's name.
Yeah, but he looks different.
All right, get out. Get out, really. It's not funny. I'm serious. It's not funny.
Got that shine now. People don't even recognize me because I'm shining.
You lost a lot of weight.
You lost a lot of weight. That's right.
Man, quit taking all them panic attack mental medicines, man.
Uh-oh.
Is that right? Were you on a... You see, let me tell you something. There's another guy who works at the station who went off his mental medicine.
And got real mental.
And he went mental. A lot of guys who are mental.
But see, I found another medication.
What is your drug? Really? What is it?
It's the Mother Earth.
It's the
cannabis
nectar. Cannabis.
Oh,
dude.
He's doing it himself
now. Listen to me.
Now he's doing the message.
The time has come.
Shaggy Too Dope, you work with Violent J. Do you see a difference in him from going off his mental medication? Are you nervous?
Big time. His new mental medication helps him out a lot more, man.
His pot.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just going to call it mental medication.
A lot of people who have mental problems, and Violent J, you have them.
Yes.
And they put you on that medication for a reason. A lot of people, all of them, as a matter of fact, always think if they go off their medication, they'll be fine, and they never are.
Well, man, I went off it and went crazy a couple times. I went to the thing a couple times.
What thing?
Mental institution?
The place.
Oh, Robin. Really?
Where do you go? Where do they lock you up?
When you're crazy, you say the place.
Yeah.
What place? What is the name of the place you go to?
My Friendly Friends. I don't know. What do you want me to get into that for? Listen, it's a special. It's over with, though. Anyway, about this sweet cannabis nectar smoke at Mary Jane that we've been talking about.
Nah, you self-medicate. Seriously, I'm worried about Violent J.
Oh, he got those purple cannons now. He's straight. Listen, man, don't be worried about me. It's raining diamonds all over us. This is the best time of our life,
yeah?
You guys. We got the greatest story in rock and roll history completing today with the release of our new album.
This is a big day for you, boy.
It's not just a record, though. You gotta understand, I'm telling you, it's not just a record we're trying to say, oh, go buy it.
What are you saying?
I'm saying for real.
This is the best thing you've got.
No, it's not just a bomb record, it's even more than that.
What is it?
For 10 years, when we first came out in 92, we said there's going to be 6 Joker cards, also known as albums, and until the end of the world, until the end of everything, in the 6th and final came out today. We've been telling a story for 10 years.
So what are you saying? Is this the end? Is this the last album you'll put out?
We man, listen, speculation.
You're the only one speculating. But, what do you mean?
We've been telling a story for 10 years, and the story ends with this album, and it's the greatest ending of all time. Like, we other artists have told a story on an album, like Journey did a concept.
Like The Who did the rock album, the rock opera.
But we spent the last ten years telling this, and we didn't have a choice to do anything else. We always knew what our next album was going to be, or the album after that. We couldn't even be creative. I mean, we're not complaining about it because we loved it so much. We were just right on track.
How long did it take you to record this album?
About 9 months.
9 months.
All over
and
America.
This is great work. This is something,
man,
that you're proud of.
It's a masterpiece. It's the best we can do, and this is the biggest day of our lives.
What record company are you with now?
D3 Entertainment. But, you know, we've always been with our own label, Psychopathic.
Psychopathic.
That's right. The one we always
have. And you have new tattoos. Your
when
whole
did
neck.
Did you do this? Yes.
Yeah, your whole neck.
I can't stop staring at his neck.
You have almost a necklace of tattoos around your neck.
Man, I just want to say one thing about where we're at today. Just one thing.
Go ahead.
Seriously, man.
What about the tattoos?
The tattoos. My brother invented a game called Morton's List. And it's a life role-playing game where you, if you don't have nothing to do, you roll the dice and it'll give you something to do. And if you don't do it after you see what it says, yeah, it's like curse, it's like bad luck. It's awesome game. Anyway, these are the different chapters. One stands for...
You have on your Adam's apple a big black dot or square.
Yeah, that's that. You might want to wipe that off.
Yeah, what is that? I think the guy messed up on that.
It looks like a butterfly.
It's an M.
Right, and you have different symbols on your neck.
Yeah, each one represents different parts of life. Man, I'm a philosophical, deep person.
What would be some of the things you'd have to do if you rolled the dice on this game and you hit
It was in all the stores everywhere, but they took it out because one of the things it happened to do was teach you how to make a bomb.
Oh.
But they make the rules before September 11th, you know, so.
Right.
Number two, you're talking about it teaches you 12,000 things to do. That's
all
one
right.
of
so
the
you things. Lost a lot of weight. You've changed your life around with the record. And what about women? You guys are getting laid now?
We didn't change our life around it. We just, you know, we just really mastered the craft of being the Insane Clown Posse.
All right. And your fans are more rabid than ever. They're downstairs. There were 50 fans down there trying to get in, trying to break through the door to get to see you.
It means just as much to them as it does us.
Right.
They've been waiting on the out. Some people grew up on this. On that stuff, all they've known is the Joker cards.
Right.
You know? And now it's today's the last and final.
You are their leader, in a sense.
No, we're not.
We're part of them.
Yeah, we're with them.
All right.
Most people.
It's really deep, but it's a great time.
Shaggy, what about you? What have you been doing?
Enjoying Miss Michigan to the fullest.
Are you going out with Miss Michigan?
looks like you're married.
Michigan.
Oh, you got married.
No, man.
What's that ring?
What is the ring?
The glove, man. I'm married to the game.
No, what are you married to?
My hand.
Did you?
Miss Michigan.
Oh, Miss Michigan is your hand. You're not dating anyone?
I just want to say to all the girls I've loved before, I'll keep loving you.
Oh, is that what it's about? You guys are playing the field?
That's right, you know.
Yeah, you were saying that in your fat days, it was hard for you to get laid as a rock star.
Still is hard.
Really?
Yeah, but I got a great story.
You must have, what is the story?
Man, this is about cute. One of your favorite people, but I don't know
who
I want to talk about.
Who is the person?
Pamela Anderson.
I was there.
What happened? Tell the truth, though. Don't lie.
I'm not going to lie because you know what? I don't have to lie to kick it.
Go ahead. Tell me what happened with you and Pamela Anderson.
Superstore.
Man, we were at the, what was the name of that club?
Hot Babes. What is it? Hot Chicks?
In L.A. It's a naked late titty bar.
Crazy Girls?
Crazy Girls.
Yeah, I know that place. Go ahead.
All right, you were at Crazy Girls.
Kick it.
We're chilling, and I see Mark McGrath chilling.
Okay, you know that's the guy from Sugar Ray.
Right, and now, you know, we got the shine, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I'm feeling good, and I'm like, let me go talk to this guy, see what's happening. So I go over there, and I'm like, aren't you Sugar Ray? You know?
Were you wearing your makeup, or were you out of your Insane Clown Posse makeup?
No, but we had an entourage of people. They knew.
You could tell you.
Anyway, so we seen him, and I start talking to him, and I'm talking to him, and he's like, you're not the dude from ICP. No, you're not. No, you're not.
He wouldn't believe us.
No. Who would doubt that you're
going to... We're going to think of somebody to lie of being, you know, like we'd pick ICP, you know?
We'd have said, oh, you don't recognize us. We play for the Chicago Bears or something.
Right, you know? But you would never lie and say you're ICP. Right.
Especially when somebody asks you. Yeah. No, you're not.
Well, you weren't in your clowny makeup, so it's It's a little difficult to spot you.
But
go ahead.
He was there, and he actually knows a lot about our group. A lot. You know, he's
a fan.
Started telling us all this stuff. You guys messed up doing this and that, whatever. And then I noticed Pamela Anderson marinating in the corner.
With Kid Rock or with Mark McGrath?
Out nobody but some other chick.
Mark McGrath was with his girlfriend. She was just hanging out with his
Is she hot?
She was
Come
so
on, Pamela Anderson, of course.
It was unbelievable.
She was hot. Mark McGrath's new girlfriend.
Oh, she was hot too. Yeah.
She was no Pamela Anderson.
Really?
You know.
All right. Yeah. Go ahead. But so you see Pamela Anderson sitting there with a girl. How long ago is this?
This was 1 week before July 19th.
Go ahead.
Why do you remember so specifically?
So July 12th?
Because it changed his life.
Because July 19th was the gathering of the Juggalos, and we were in L.A. 1 week prior.
Okay, go ahead.
So anyway, I just was like, you know, talking to Sugarloaf, and I was like, forget him, and I slid over to Pam Anderson, and I'm like, what's up, you know? And she was drinking, and she's like, what's up? And I'm like, yeah, I'm in ICP, I know Bob real good, talking about Kid Rock. And she's
I'm surprised she was drinking if she has the Hep C.
I'm saying everybody was just...
All right.
I'm trying
everyone was partying, all right.
You know, everybody was just like, it wasn't out of place for me to step to it.
Right. She might be drinking water.
Story short that nobody in America is going to believe, but it's all... good because it happened. And if you got your pickle buffed and nobody believed you, would it really matter?
No.
That's
you know what I'm saying?
Right, so go ahead. So what happened?
But I'm saying you get the point of the... Anyway, we talked for about 45 minutes. I said, aren't you guys getting married? She said, no, we're not getting married. We're just friends. This is a week before July 19th.
Like,
she said,
rings?
You see any rings on my fingers? And I'm like, no. And she's like, I'm like, oh, I thought y'all were whatever. She's like, oh, you know, my kids, I can't move to Michigan, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, well, that's all fine and dandy, but what's up, you know?
And what's up with us? Right.
I'm just like, what's happened, you know? Here's what I think happened, because she said, after about 45 minutes, she said, what are you doing tomorrow?
Go ahead.
We had mad stuff to do the next day.
What were you doing?
We had photos and a commercial to shoot, all, but I was like...
So that makes you look good.
Nothing. Tomorrow? I was like, we ain't got a damn thing going on tomorrow. What's up? You know, she was like, I want you to come to my place in Malibu.
Oh.
That's what she said, Malibu. And she said, we're having a barbecue, right?
Go ahead.
And I was like, man, wow, that would be, man, get out of here. I was like, you, man, in Malibu, man, you want us to come up there? Hell yeah, we'll come up there. She said, no, not everybody, just you.
Oh, not even Shaggy Too Dope, your partner.
Now, I will say she did not connect me in the eyes or rub my leg or nothing, but she was like, no, I'm not talking about everybody, you know.
Right, just you.
So
come
then how could Pimpalicious right here play his cards? What could I do? Could I just start freaking out and jumping all over that like, oh, well, yeah. You know, I was like, you know what?
that sounds good and everything, but, man, I'll come out there tomorrow if the next day you and your kids come see me and Shaggy wrestle, because we had a wrestling match that Sunday.
Nice.
And she was like, oh, my boys love wrestling. And I'm like, put them in a little headlock. Yeah. And she's like, yeah.
You put her in a headlock?
No, I'm just, you know, I'm talking about, just, come on, I'm just.
Go ahead. Yeah, so you're catching a vibe that she's interested in the great Violent J.
In the game of the great
Right,
Jay.
Right.
Now,
she's caught up in your game.
Let me just say something right now before people trip. I realize she probably had a huge argument with Kid Rock and knows Kid Rock hates us from back in Detroit and was like, this guy's a clown. If I
can't
hit him.
Let me just say something right now. Shaggy, is this all true?
100% true, brother.
Okay,
it was a whole bottle of
whole whip.
Well, right. Nothing happened.
So now, here's the good part
of
the story.
This part's even unbelievable.
Here goes the
You got
stuff.
To sit next to her, and they didn't throw you out of the club.
Man, look at this, man. We're part of the Insane Clown Posse. We don't go to Hollywood parties. This is every bit of unbelievable.
Right. Go ahead.
Man.
It's not like she gave him a shoulder ride backwards. You know?
Right. Okay.
So, then Mark McGrath, you know, he's talking, blah, 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 man. You guys, you know, oh, man, you guys need to do a song with the Neptunes, man. Why do you guys keep... Why don't you guys do something?
Tell him to shut up.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, hey, you know what? Do what he wants
to do.
Especially
when I'm like, rap to Pamela Anderson, you know?
And I'm like, do you know what it would be like?
Same clown posse.
I'm like, do you know what it would be like if we did a single with the Neptunes and all of a sudden had like a number one single, the Juggalos would kill us? And he's like, he said, F the Juggalos.
Ooh.
Now right there.
Did you kick his ass?
My boy, the Rude Boy and Sabu, who's a wrestler, but he's also... homie, and he was there for the commercial. They both walked up on Sugarloaf and were like, what did you say? So I took that advantage and I skipped back over to Pamela. And I said, so what's up? She's like, we're going to the after party. You got to come to the after party. You got to come to the after party.
She's always got some party.
She's always busy.
And I didn't go to no parties. I was like, damn, it's so damn near midnight. I should have
got kids at home.
Yeah, right.
But I was like, yeah, I'm going to the party. Okay, well, yeah, I'm still playing it all super suave.
Where's her kids?
Suave. The last time players heard that was swats.
All right, go ahead.
Swats.
This was an event, but there was an after party?
So go ahead.
So anyway, she's like, you better be coming. I said, I'm coming with you. She's like, let's go right now. All of a sudden, Sugarloaf comes back around. He's like, wait a minute, Jay, I have to talk to you. I'm about to get my ass kicked, Pam. Can I talk to him for a minute? Pam's like, we're leaving right now, Mark. Can I talk to him? Look, give me 5 minutes with him. Are you guys going to the party? I'll bring you. This is him talking to me. So she's like, you better bring him.
Oh,
and
wow.
She's like, I'll bring him. Just give me 5 minutes with him. So out goes Pamela Anderson. Now we're talking to Sugarloaf. He dips off in the bathroom again and ducks out the back door.
Oh.
Asian to the bullets.
Why would he do that?
He's about to get his jaw rocked.
Oh, my God.
I mean, we weren't even looking for no trouble.
But you should have stayed with Pamela Anderson and gone to the party
with
her.
Guy.
Why would you stay with a guy unless you were homosexuals? I mean, what are you thinking?
What are you doing?
I mean, she does got that little problem with her net, and you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but what are you guys thinking?
I was already gone by that point, man. I couldn't stand.
Look, man.
So what happened? Well, that's it? No Malibu? No nothing?
Man.
Oh.
He lost the thread.
What a lousy ending.
Terrible.
What's the whole point? Wait a minute.
What a terrible story.
How many people can walk this earth and say that they were invited by Pamela Anderson to her Malibu house?
Yeah, but you didn't get to go.
It's only you've been mad or
that's terrible.
How could that be?
You blew it.
Man,
that is so much no story. We should have known with all the buildup.
Yeah, I mean, and then you go, wow, and that's not all. Guess what happened next?
Yeah.
We went in the bathroom with Sugar Ray.
Oh, man.
I mean, what kind of story is that?
I actually looked up from the picture of Keith Richards' daughter for a little while.
Yeah, I thought we were going somewhere with this.
Right, yeah.
I thought we were going to hear you bang somebody.
Pam asked me out all the time. That's what everybody's thinking.
She didn't ask you out. She dumped you at the club.
She asked me out to the weekend.
If she wanted
a weekend worth of this right here.
Yeah,
she didn't even want one night. She was like, damn, I need at least 3 days.
Why didn't she give you a phone number? Why
did
you
almost look at it this way, man? Because she had to work anyway, so he played her.
No, he didn't.
He was like, you better be there.
He didn't get laid.
I thought I was on my way to the after party. I was like, it's all right. We don't even got to kick this dude's ass if he's taking us to the party. Let's roll. But he ducked.
Well, I don't know. I don't know how you let him get away with that. And I don't know how you didn't get her phone number if he's so into you.
Why would he not go with Pam? Why is he hanging around?
Man, you guys are missing the whole thing.
I guess Mark is prettier than Pam.
I don't believe what's happening.
I don't believe what you did.
Man, wait a minute.
I'm busting you.
Who's listening to us right now, man? Them are
everyone.
Real people out there, man. These
real people would have been in the party with
real
Ben
people. Well, I was doing everything I thought was my best possible route to hitting that ass. I was taking every possible... I was playing my cards.
Shaggy, do you laugh at Violent J?
My point is,
no,
wait a minute.
I understand
hold
what you're
up.
Saying.
No,
my
you
point
don't.
Is, sir,
no.
If we was hanging out in a bar having drinks with anybody and I just happened to tell that story, that ain't that bad.
Oh,
that's
come on.
Oh,
did you
get,
did you guys say the chick from the corner picked you up?
The whole story... And she said, go to a party with me.
You know what the problem
you
is?
Didn't.
You know what
did
the
you
problem
get Mark
is?
McGrath's number?
You guys have been around. You guys have been around too many superstars.
No, man. If a girl says to me, come out to Malibu,
soft.
I go, give me the address so I can be there.
That ain't a girl.
10 years
Sam
in the
Anderson.
Game. Listen to this. 10 years in the game. 10 years out here we've been touring. 10 years, and we still can appreciate a story like that. That's because
no.
That ain't gone to our head.
You had, the opportunity to go to the ranch, and you didn't get
you
her
blew
number.
It.
You blew it. That's
the only thing getting blown is this piece right here next time I bump into
it. I don't see it. Let's see.
There were two possible great endings to that story. Banging Pam Anderson or kicking Mark McGrath's ass. And neither one happened.
You would have seen how Mark Sugar Wolf was acting. You know what I'm saying?
Well, dude, I can top you. I blew it with Pam Anderson, too. So don't feel so bad.
Because you're also a scrub like us.
Let me tell you what happened with me. You want to hear a real story? And I'll cut to the chase.
A real story.
I took Pam Anderson to Scores.
So then you're even worse. You
wait a second. This is a flop. We're there. We're partying at Scores. There's tons of strippers. We're in a back room.
This is pre-hepatitis C. Okay?
Yeah, pre-hep C.
Man, I would have tapped it raw.
Give me some of that C.
You
keep quiet.
You
give me that.
The bathroom with Mark McGrath.
Give me some of that C.
I don't mind. I got that already. I got some A and B.
Four. You got that.
I got the whole alphabet already. Let's come get you.
You got hep A through Z.
Spectrum.
No, to make a long story short, she kissed me.
He beat me out right there.
She was sitting on your lap, right?
She sat on my lap and kissed me.
Yeah, game over.
Hold on.
And,
like a movie kiss, you know what I'm saying?
She kissed me.
Or is it real?
It wasn't real. It was like on the lips, but I don't... There
was it
any,
a passion kiss? Or a friend kiss? I miss
like,
you. I'll see you later.
It was... My buddy was rubbing her legs, and I was kissing her.
Don't you understand? That's what really matters. Was it a passion kiss, or was it some bull? I mean, come on. That's what really matters. If she really was, like, kissing you, like,
no,
I got to kiss
no,
your
no,
face.
She
you're
wasn't,
so hot to
no,
me.
She didn't. She that's why I left, because I didn't think she really wanted me.
And she invited you to another party, too. There was something to go to. And
I had to go to work.
Can I tell you something about my story? A little bit fresher, just to put the icing on. She did it down low style. It wasn't like she wasn't standing up like, let's go out, bring your friends. We were talking to each other under our breasts.
Okay.
Under your breasts?
Under her breasts.
My breasts.
She's hot, though, right?
No,
she... But you didn't sit next to her? You didn't put your arm around her?
We sat down next to each other, nestled off on a little love.
You guys ready to take a couple of phone calls? You wanted, in honor of your new album?
Yeah,
the Wrath, Shangri-La.
The Wraith.
The Wraith.
The Wraith?
The Wraith.
Let me just say
this,
man.
The Wrath of the Wraith.
The Wraith.
I gotta say one more thing, man, if you can let me just, because I don't forget, we're not upset no more, man. Like, we're not going to come out here and bitch and moan about not getting MTV or not getting radio play, because all we're doing is looking past all the love and all the juggalos we got and looking for stuff to bitch about, man, and we're tired of that.
Yeah,
man.
You're positive now. This is a new
over the 10 last years, we fought and built a juggalo family, them people outside our family. Now it's time to stop fighting and start being a family, and let's just start
right.
doing
so
our
I
thing,
think what
man.
You're saying is the people call in and
I want to celebrate for what we
all
got,
right
you
let's
know?
Take some nice phone calls and see what happens.
No, bring the haters on, but they won't dole a shine. We're like 10,000 suns in a glass jar.
All right, let's see. Jimmy, you're on the air with Insane Clown Posse. Their new album is the finale in a 10-year story called The Wraith. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Hey Howard, my name's Jimmy. I own a construction company. I got a job the next 2 weeks. I'll pay these guys under the table, $10 an hour. If they work a full 8 hours, I'll give them $100 a day. They just got to clean up after the job, throw all the scrap into a container that gets lugged away.
Tell you what, why don't you and your boys come build my home theater, and I'll give y'all $5 an hour and a kick in the ass if you get my carpets dusted.
I'm just trying to help you out. Let you get an honest day's work in. Maybe you earn some money.
Guys, just trying to help you. Let's go to Brandy. Brandy,
yeah,
go ahead.
I'll put that $10 an hour on top of the $50 million already in the bank. Thanks, partner.
Do you have $50 million in the bank?
Hell no.
Oh.
But I'm hood rich. So if I have $50,000, that's every bit of $50 million.
That's right. Brandy, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hi. I just wanted to call and say to you guys all think that this is all funny, like the whole slit and throats and raping girls and everything, and I'm just going to say that it's not funny.
What happened? You got raped.
That was funny.
All right, slow down, time. Can we get some sentimental music? Call in right now. Tell us about how you got tapped.
Well, let's hear what Brandy's thoughts are. What do you say?
Who sings about? Call somebody else with that. Who sings about rape, bitch? We don't sing about rape. Don't try to call up here and slip that in. Slitting throats, rape. Name one song we ever sung about rape. You better take that to the suicide hotline, bitch.
Right? Unless it was anti-rape.
The hell out of here with that. Who? We don't care you got raped, man. You don't do it for attention. Slitting throats, getting fingers stuck in your butt.
Let's see what Brandy has to say.
You know, hold on.
Because I know where this is going. We've been here.
Say right now. Hi, I'm Brandy, and I've never actually listened to one of your records.
Brandy, have you listened to the records?
Yes, I have.
Because they're a bomb.
That's right. You like them too, don't you?
No, I don't.
Well, you're bad. You're missing out.
Well, you know how to stop. Check this out. I figured one thing out. If you really, really don't like our music,
don't listen.
You can just not play.
There you go.
Because, you know, it's just going to play it. I bet you it'll help.
Well, Brandy.
Would you like to name their rape song?
Yeah. Or the lyric.
Yeah.
I don't know the lyrics. I'm not going to sit there and listen to them all the time.
Like you.
Brandy, what do you have to say to us?
Okay, well, can I tell you the story of what happened to me?
Okay.
Yeah.
You don't want to hear it?
Now. Get the violin.
We want to hear it?
Okay, is this all of a sudden a crisis? So we about to get it. Let's hear about it. What the hell's that got to do with us?
Brandy, go ahead.
Okay, we'll make a long story short.
Please.
My best friend was murdered. The guy in that vodka, he split her throat. And he choked me and threw me over a bridge and left me for dead.
And he
was the one who said that one of the reasons he did it was because he listened to your music.
That's because he's crazy.
No, he's not.
Crazy.
Well, Brandy, in all fairness,
you're crazy.
In all fairness to the boys, I mean, many people have tried to blame violence on music over the years.
We always slip subliminals in their.
There are crazy people who listen to music and then
go off. Yeah.
I mean, people listen to the church and go crazy.
That's what entertainment is. I mean, we provide horror music instead of horror movies.
Maybe you should have got on some of that Violent J medicine. That's you know what I'm saying?
But you have to feel bad for her that her friend was murdered.
So, that sucks.
Yeah, but
you know what I mean?
She called up here trying to get ends for herself.
For something. She needs to be slapped for that
I wouldn't tell nobody if that happened to me.
You going to call and tell the Howard Stern listeners about a tragedy like that? How personal it is? How personal is it to you?
So basically,
bitch?
I'm Brandy and send me some money because
Bitch.
All right, well, Brandy, the boys aren't sympathetic to what you're saying.
Here.
This ain't no Dr. Phil.
That ain't the suicide hotline.
Thank you, Brandy, though.
Try wearing an iron turtleneck.
All right, Brandy did not go over well with the boys.
It didn't make a dent.
Brandy, go out and get their new album.
There's a time and a place for that.
Phil, go ahead. Phil, you're on the air.
Not us. That's like asking us our comments on world tragedies. What the
Yes, Phil.
Hey, Howard, how you doing? I travel the country speaking against violent music, and I just want the boys to know I talk about them every day.
My man.
And
my
dog. In fact, I'm currently in St. Louis speaking to schools all day.
Hey, how's that promo tour going anyway?
I need some samples. You promote murder to
keep
kids.
Keep doing what you're doing.
Hey, Howard, do you want me to quote some of their lyrics?
All right, go ahead.
Yeah.
Do it.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Come on, we'll rap with you.
Can I use obscenities or can I just have to bleep them out?
Bleep them out.
49 MFers dead. Keep your B in place. I'm going to send her home with a footprint on her face. I'm hating sluts. Shoot him in the face. Grab her by the arm. Grab her by the life and take it.
Let me ask you, is that any different than a Freddy Krueger movie that has killing virgins and slashing and murdering? Is it
Somebody wrote that, too.
Let me ask you this, Howard.
You know what? This is the same case as that brand.
It's okay to promote murder to children.
If you're going to go
promoting Jesus.
If you're going to do that, you got to ban horror movies and slasher movies.
Horror movies are rated R, right?
Yes.
ICP sings to children. They promote murder.
Yeah, we got explicit warning things on
it. You have a warning on your record?
Warning means nothing, Howard. I went to their show in Cleveland. You want to know how big a punk ICP is? They won't even talk to me. They dodged me for 2 years now. And I saw kids, children, 10 years old at their concerts.
You know what this guy is?
I got 6 year old kids coming to my shows, you
this
know?
This guy is invisible.
Alex Vista, they wouldn't come out from back.
I don't like any censorship because even the Bible promotes killing children that disrespect their parents. I don't know if you know that.
Hey,
and people have killed their own kids because of the Bible.
There are actual cases linked to this violent music of these guys.
He loves you and you got chicks in here.
Let me tell you something. Keep doing what you're doing, man, because, hey, we appreciate it.
Yeah,
stay down with the clown. Keep
your panties out of your ass. Hey, Jay, people are throwing their albums away, and we're going to do our best to stop sales.
Good, because he's going to spread the word to
you. You guys keep doing it.
Every day, bro.
Hey, keep doing what you're doing, man.
What are you going to stop dodging? Hey, we're True Lies. You talk. We have a video called True Lies, all about a lot about ICP. And I want to know, Jay, when are you going to stop dodging me?
It's okay. Dodging you. I'll meet you anywhere and whip that.
All right, well, I'll be calling your manager, bro.
There is Phil, who says he's going to meet with you.
Our website's truelies.utalks.com.
That's what he wanted. A free plug for his website.
Yeah.
Our website's www.
Like anybody's listening to Howard Stern show, it's going to go to something about
Howard.
I want to help out.
Howard.
Yeah. Down.
Run commercials during the commercial break, too, you genius.
All right.
And what the hell are you doing listening if you hate it? Get out of here.
Thank you, Phil. Well, there it is. There's Phil.
Thank Phil a lot for that.
Finally, I'll tell you, there was about 50 people out there trying to get to see you.
Did I see some of these people?
Man, do you guys want to know something? I hate to cut you off, but
yeah.
About what we were talking about, the violence, just to finish that out, man. Hey, man.
All right, you said it all. That says it all. The only girls that came down here to see ICP were fat and under 18. But I'm just reporting. But a lot of guys, a lot of dudes.
You act like that's a bad thing.
You like fat chicks who are under 18?
That's my preferred, preferably.
Really? All right, well, there you go.
We're sharing a cell with R. Kelly.
Who are the people that, bring in a few of the people that were down here who are huge fans of ICP. There's a guy. What is your name, sir?
Hello.
Deans.
Dean, and you're an ICP fan?
Yes, Mr. Stern.
Yeah,
he's a juggalo.
P-Town Juggalos.
All right, and what about the guy in the middle there?
Dustin,
how old are you?
I'm 17.
17, and you're a huge ICP fan?
Oh, yeah.
Do our records make you want to murder somebody and choke your girlfriend and throw up a bride?
All the time it makes you want to murder.
Hey,
maybe that guy had a point.
Uh-oh. Let me tell you something. If you feel something about our music that makes you want to do something, nothing to it but to do it.
Really?
If I can.
Really?
If you're that sick anyway, come on, man, you can't distinguish. You think we really run around and axe murder people?
And what is your name, sir?
I'm Chris.
And Chris, you're a huge fan, too. Always. Anything you want to say to the boys?
Music just touches me.
It touches me. Well, there you go. Well, you have your fans. And Cabby, what do you want to say?
Well, I actually, I work in the industry, Howard, and I'm not the biggest IPC fan, but rumor has it that their record's going to debut at number one.
Really?
It's going to be one of the biggest records shipped this year, and that's no lie.
There it is. Well, there it goes. Well,
and I just want to say to Silent Bob and Jay or whatever their guys' names is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you guys still fat?
As a matter of fact.
Violent. You could relate to this, Cabby. Violent J, you must have lost 100 pounds, dude.
Did you take Crim Spa?
No, he didn't.
No, he went off his medication like you did.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
That's How did you lose weight getting off your medication? I almost killed people when I stopped taking my medication.
The sweet nectar of the earth, as a matter of fact, brother.
He's on marijuana.
Cabby, you can't do what he did. Yeah.
You can't really stick to your medicine.
I also want to know, who are you guys voting for in your big election today?
Knew there was one.
No, these guys are not political, Cabby. Thank you so much.
Talk about the slammies?
Boys, go ahead. Say something to your hero, because I've run out of time. But
Thanks a lot. Keep the music coming.
It only gets better from here, man.
Insane Clown Posse's new album, The Wraith, Shangri-La, featuring the single Homies, is available in stores today. The rumor has it, according to Kevin, it will debut as number one.
Oh, that'll be
if
something
if that happens,
me.
Man, I just want to say I'd like to collect my $50,000 from Sharon Osbourne.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Paid up. I thought we were record. Supposed to be washed up like 4 years ago or something, right?
Remember in 97, right. The fluke of the week?
And you guys have a lot of ICP tattoos. Is that it? What do you have on you?
He's got Dark Lotus on the hands. From the pendulum, we got some tattoos on the neck.
You guys want to know what a dark lotus is?
There it is.
A lotus is a flower that grows at night, and juggalos weren't often given sunlight, but we still grow and blossom like beautiful dark lotuses. Underground.
And what does it say on your arm? Juggalo?
Juggalo. For the day I die. Love him, Howard.
ICP tour dates, go to InsaneClownPosse.com. And we have to go. Boys, always good to see you.
Man, thank you, man.
Good you always you. Bring a lot of...
Thank you guys again, man.
Were you happy that Sharon Osbourne got cancer?
I was upset about anybody getting cancer, but I just want to know when I'm going to get paid.
We'll be back right after these words.
You know, in the Christmas spirit, I always try to do something beautiful for someone, and I've done it.
What did you do?
Well, the last time Insane Clown Posse was here, I was talking with them, and they said, you know, we'd like to... I forget how it all came about, but they were like, you know, we'd like to get into a studio with someone like Debbie Gibson or, you know, Tiffany or someone... I don't know who they said, but
I forget who they said exactly.
Yeah, we'd like to get in, you know, someone you'd never think we'd record with and record a song with. I said, well, I know Debbie Gibson. I mean, Deborah Gibson.
Well, whoever. You know, right. Somebody named Gibson.
So, on the phone, I'm going to hook it up right now. Is that Deborah Gibson?
Hello.
Hey, baby.
Hey.
Hold on. Excuse me. I didn't mean to do that. Excuse
me. Charming.
Violin J, you there?
What up?
Hey.
Chilling, man. What's up?
Violin J, you said to me, you had an idea that if I could put you together with Debbie Gibson, do you know anything about this, Debbie?
I know all about it.
Oh, okay. The idea was that you felt you could go into the studio with her and take one of her hit songs and redo it?
No. Make something brand new where it's not about the past no more. See, I got a master plan behind this whole thing. I mean, seriously, I got a master plan. We're going to use each other's careers to elevate each other.
All right, and what song, have you had any discussion with Debbie Gibson? Have you ever spoken to her before?
No, we've never spoken.
No, we're speaking right now. We're making history right now.
Debbie, this is Violent J.
How you doing, Jay?
I'm doing so good. How are you?
I'm good.
Jay's a white guy. I don't know if you know that.
Yeah, it's hard to tell under the makeup. You wear the makeup, do you?
He wears the clown makeup.
No, you know, it doesn't. Nobody knows what, you know, we got the makeup on. That's our race.
Is Jay back on drugs?
Jay, are you on drugs?
I'm smoking a fat-ass blunt in front of my fireplace, chilling. I'm feeling good.
Well, Jay, I'm clearly white.
Okay.
So this is going to be interesting.
Jay, is it a goof that you want to work with Debbie Gibson, or are you going to treat her as a serious artist? She is a serious artist.
Oh, of course. Listen to what I'm saying. That's my plan. See, people don't think we're serious artists.
Right.
But if we work with an established, super respected, super talent, then everybody will look at us like, now there's no way Deborah would have ever worked with them fools unless they weren't fools.
Wouldn't it be great if Violent J, you know, worked with Debbie, they had a big hit song together, and then they fell in love and they got married. And Debbie,
that would be incredible.
And then Debbie started wearing clown makeup.
What's her name going to be?
That would be cool and everything, but, you know.
Depressed Debbie.
And I don't mean to bring this up. It's the Christmas season and everything, but I do want to, since I'm sort of involved in this, I'm just scared you guys are going to rape her or something, are you?
Is it safe?
Is it safe for her to work with you?
Howard, you've got to be at the session to protect me.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Well, you can bring some bodyguards.
You bring some bodyguards.
Well, you know how it is. I just bring my mom.
Violent J, can you...
would we rape her?
Yeah.
Number one, you can't rape the willing.
Oh!
Oh, dear God!
And when we get there, and she's in the presence of the Dark Carnival and Jay and Shaggy,
it would be a whole nother person. Even Deb, even you don't, even you are underestimating the powers of us in the studio.
That's all right, so shine. You're not looking to have sex with her, though, are you? I mean, it's.
I'm looking to get paid. First things first.
All right, Debbie. Debbie's a virgin.
Yes, a 32-year-old virgin.
Yeah, no, but no seriousness. It's a legitimate working situation, right?
See, look, the way I benefit is we all of a sudden get the world-class respect we need. And the way that she benefits is that you get this hardcore serial killer audience that's there for you every time you need them.
Is that what you were looking for, Debbie?
You're finally going to get your dream. So, Violent J, what do you suggest is the best way to go about this? Debbie, where are you living now?
I'm in New York.
All right, you're in New York. And where are you boys right now?
I'm in Detroit.
All right. Now, what is this?
We're anywhere we need to be, though, you know.
Do you want me to have you two exchange numbers? And then, Debbie, are you interested in this proposition?
Yeah, I got to do it. This sounds like a trip.
It sounds funny.
Right there, totally funny. That's amazing. That's so cool to me. That right there flips my wig.
Does Debbie need to do anything? She is a songwriter.
You guys are going to collaborate, right?
Yeah, that's what I want to do.
Where are we getting together in Detroit?
Yeah, can you come here? You wouldn't come here, would you?
I love Detroit.
Well, then come here. Because we got the bomb studio. We can do everything. I can send you a gang of tracks in advance, and you can pick whatever sounds nice.
Perfect.
Now, wait a second. Hold it.
From there.
Violent J, you're saying you have tracks now. Do you need Debbie to write lyrics?
Well, I was thinking if it's going to be a true collaboration, yeah.
So now, are we going to do a kind of thing where, like, you guys rap a verse, I sing a verse, or, you know?
Or maybe vice versa.
Uh-huh.
You know, like, what if we hit them up with, you know, every time the beat keeps switching up to something kind of smooth and then really hard. And then, you know, everybody thinks we're going to be on the really hard parts and then you're going to be on the smooth, but no, we flipping on them.
See, I actually had a little practice with that kind of thing because I sang backgrounds on a Circle Jerks song.
Yeah, well,
and performed it live with them at CBGB, so.
That's nothing.
That's really nothing, Debbie.
Yeah.
Oh, it was something for me, man.
This is something for you.
This isn't going to turn into a thing like Mariah Carey and Eminem, though, where, you know, you guys, maybe it doesn't work out.
Anything I'm involved in could never turn out to be anything like Eminem's involved in.
All right, so you're not looking to just F her. You're gonna actually be serious and treat this in a serious manner.
But I'm going to do first things first is all I'm saying.
Debbie, is this going to be okay with your mom?
My mom is fully, she's probably listening right now.
All right, so you'll clear it with her?
What?
You'll clear it with your mommy?
Well, dear God, my momager is totally with it.
Right, and Violent J, what about your mom? She's all right with this?
I'm saying, Debbie, you could bring your mom and she can hang out with my mom.
Yeah.
You know what? She's seen it all, done it all, so she'll be there.
All right, here's what I'm going to do. Debbie, I'm going to give you Violent J's phone number.
Okay.
I don't think we should do it the other way around.
All right.
And Debbie,
I like that way. Give me his number.
Debbie, how are you, by the way? Everyone knows you with that goody two-shoes image. You're obviously not a virgin anymore, right?
What do you mean anymore? Like I was last time I was there?
I don't know. And who are you seeing? Are you dating someone?
Yeah.
Who are you seeing?
I've been with the same person for a year.
Who is the guy? What does he do?
I think we talked about this last time. He's in the money management investment banking world.
I see.
Oh, good. Not in the biz.
No, not
Robin predicts you're going to get married at some point.
No, I did not say that about Debbie.
Right.
Not ready for marriage yet.
I understand he's an Orthodox Jew. Is that true?
He's not Orthodox, but yes, he's Jewish and he's very passionate about his religion.
Oh, so you're going to convert?
I don't know. See, that's the crossroads we're at right now.
Wow, Debbie Gibson's going to be a Jew.
Yeah. You know what? That's people funny. Think I'm a Jew anyway.
They do?
Yeah, I don't know anyone. I got the schnoz. They think I'm a Jew.
Did you do a Christmas album?
What?
I got a question for Debbie. Debbie, yeah. have you ever been approached by Playboy?
I have been several times.
And you're not, have you ever considered
You're still holding
it?
Out?
There was one time I was considering it. You know, I just wanted to be open-minded and consider it and, you know, but I wanted to do it, like, with a Matthew Ralston or a Herb Ritz or whatever, and they basically want to be the cheapo staff photographer, and I said no thanks.
What, can I ask you what kind of money they throw at you for that, for Debbie Gibson?
They throw you, like, $500,000.
Whoa.
Mm. I'd do it with any photographer for half a million.
No.
Did they want to see everything, like the
I'd much rather be working with the Insane Clown Posse.
Did you get to the point? But did you get to the point in the discussion where they say, okay, you definitely have to show the top, and you're gonna have to show some.
Yes, you do. And I was like, you know what? I just don't. I'm a New Yorker. I'm on the streets all the time, running around. I just don't need people looking me in the eye. I haven't seen everything.
But did they want you to show hair or show the whole beef?
You know what? They didn't get that descriptive, but they did just say top and bottom.
So in other words, your legs spread so we could really examine you.
Yeah.
Did you see Tiffany's?
Yeah.
Everybody's seen that.
I mean, like that. You know.
Hey, let me make a point. When you go to a titty bar, it's always the waitresses that look the best. That's because they got their clothes on, and you always want to see them because it leads more to the imagination.
Exactly.
Tiffany, play yourself out.
We're going to hit it off just fine.
All right, I can't wait to hear this. Then when will I have the exclusive to play this on my show?
Of course, you hooked it up. You're the matchmaker here, Howard.
All right,
very good.
You know what, I think the last part of Debbie's E! True Hollywood story is going to begin like this. Coming up, Debbie boards a plane to Detroit.
Well, you know, this could finally get me my E! True Hollywood story, because I just never do anything remotely scandalous.
Yeah, well, whatever.
What are you wearing now?
I'm wearing sweats and a pajama top.
And Violent J, what are you wearing?
I'm wearing some puff pillow slippers.
But you're not wearing your clown makeup, are you?
Oh, no, hell no.
No, all right. And when you work with Debbie, will you wear clown makeup?
I doubt it. Not in my studio.
See the real Violent J?
No, yeah. Oh, in the studio. We're real, all about realness.
Where is the studio?
This is so cool because if she comes, I can show her our whole complex. We got our own everything. We're not connected to no major label. There's none of that here. So.
Oh, that's an enticement.
You wouldn't believe what we do here.
I knew that. You used to be on Island, didn't you?
Yeah.
What happened?
We got off our Island because when they merged with Def Jam Records, everything went to hell for us.
Well, let me ask you this.
Huh?
Is the studio in your home?
No, we got a complex.
A complex? What does that mean?
We're like mafia dons here. We run this place.
And when Debbie comes...
You so well for yourself that you have a complex?
Yeah, how many...
We got 35 employees.
How many days does Debbie need to spend there, do you know?
Oh, it'll be a one-day thing, yeah.
All right, okay.
But, you know, if she wants to stay a couple extra, she's welcome to stay with me.
In your crib.
Yeah. Of course.
I was just in Detroit this past summer opening the new Ford Field. I love Detroit.
All right.
There's all kind of new stuff everywhere.
I love it.
All right, let's see what happens from the two of you collaborating.
I can't wait to see what this collaboration creates.
I hope it yields a hit. Debbie Gibson, thank you. I mean, Deborah Gibson.
Just Deb. How about Deb?
Debs.
We can make it real easy for you, Howard.
And Violent J, I think you're going to be joining Debbie Gibson and her boyfriend in synagogue.
Mazel tov.
That's nice.
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
You're the man for hooking that up.
All right, brother. Let's see if you come through.
Oh, we're coming through for you.
Pressure's on you now, brother.
All right.
You don't stand me up like you did the other day with the phoner.
What happened?
Yeah, what happened to your boner?
Phoner.
I don't
know what I'm the last to know. We just got off the road.
All right, well, you were supposed to be on the phone the other day, and you weren't there.
Oh, I'm sorry, man.
So
I'm here now.
You better be there.
Yeah, and don't screw this up.
All right.
Later. Violent J, Debbie Gibson, collaborating Debbie Gibson. Let's see. Insane Clown Posse's album, The Wraith, Shangri-La, is available in stores now.
He's got a complex in Detroit. He must be worth $40,000.
And go to InsaneClownPosse.com, Debbie Gibson. So you're going to give them each the numbers?
Yes.
Okay, hook them up. I'm a fan of Insane Clown Posse, even though they think I'm not.
Why don't you tell me one of your favorite songs of theirs?
No, I'm a fan of theirs, not their songs.
Oh, not
I wouldn't know
music.
One from the other. I would like to play some of their music if I could find it somewhere. But they are very, very successful. They're one of the most successful bands monetarily.
How could this be?
Well, they've got a huge following. And they're huge in Detroit.
So they sell a lot of records and they make a lot of money touring is what you're telling me.
And I have never seen the guys Shaggy Too Dope and Insane Violent J. I have never seen them outside of their clown makeup. And I probably never will.
I saw Violent J on the street one day without the clown makeup.
Wow. Hey, Violent J is slimming down.
Look at you. Getting healthy.
Shaggy 2 Dope always was thin.
Yeah.
Shaggy 2 Dope wearing some sort of ace bandage on his hand. It looks like he injured himself.
What did he do?
Did you get in a fight?
I wouldn't call it a fight there, Howard. I'd call it more of an ass whipping.
Your ass got whipped?
No, come on. My hand got whipped, but that's about it.
Whose ass did you whip?
It was during that day where the power went out.
You know? Oh, really?
It was hot out. Some kid popped his lips off.
What did he say to you?
He threw a beer can at my face.
Why would he do that? Did he know that you were... Did he know you were you?
I don't even know if he knew he did it.
Oh, I see. It was an accident.
No, he was just out of his mind. Drunk and high.
And you beat him up?
Yeah.
Well, I don't blame you. He threw something at you. You have every right to do that.
What are you going to do, you know?
Yes.
I'd have a wrist brace on, too, if I'd have been there.
Right. Violent J, how'd you lose the weight?
Man, it wasn't so much that I wanted to lose weight as much as I discovered, like, I like to run at night. You know what I mean?
You've been running? Really? Look at you. In the makeup?
Well, see, I don't
know. That's got to be rough.
Keeping in bedroom windows and right. Running and hopping fences.
Right.
No, but, yeah, man, you know, that's really what it was.
It looks like Robin lost some weight, too.
Yeah, 70 pounds.
See, man.
She likes to run at night also.
What were you just talking about, some product?
Let me talk to you, Trim Spa.
That's what it is.
Let me tell you something.
Worldwide.
People say to me, how is it that you think Insane Clown Posse is successful? I'm going to read you some statistics, okay, just so you understand who these two gentlemen are.
That's right.
Explain to us.
ICP moves about $15,000 of merchandise a day, mostly through online sales, a pace that would mean nearly $6 million in annual revenues. So while you quietly, you're not as, let's say, visible as Puff Daddy with his clothing line and things, you're saying Insane Clown Posse materials.
What are they selling? What kind of merchandise?
Yeah, what are you selling?
Name it. Anything you can imagine.
Name it.
Anything you can imagine.
Think of something, we make it.
See, we move through the underground. We don't just... have a tunnel, but we have a whole world dug in the underground.
But you don't get...
There's an alternative to mainstream right now.
They call us Harriet Tubman because we run with the underground.
Right, just like Harriet Tubman, the famous black underground. Slave days.
I'm smart, man.
Yeah.
Black Harriet Tubman?
That's right.
Was she moving merchandise?
Absolutely.
Moving it for us.
Yeah. But let me say, you guys don't get respect. In fact, in your new book... Of course, ICP Behind the Paint, available.
It's a good book.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a good book.
You even say, I think Howard Stern likes us, but I don't think he likes our music, doesn't know our music. You feel Robin doesn't even like you personally.
What?
That's right. You do write that.
I do like you personally.
No.
It's ridiculous.
It says here, and I'll read right from the book.
Get out publicly.
The truth is, I don't think Howard Stern really takes ICP that seriously as a musical group. He has bands that he personally likes to listen to, like Marilyn Manson and others that he told us he likes. Unfortunately, just like pretty much the rest of America, he just looks at us as a novelty joke band. Hey, that's okay. He's still cool because he has us on the show three times a year. And he says, Robin Quivers hates ICP.
No, I didn't say that.
What are you talking about?
I didn't say that.
Damn.
I said, I don't think she likes us on the count that she claims she's seen me in front of Virgin Records, paintless, and I ignored her and brushed her off to the side, and that never happened.
Oh, here we go.
Remember the old school? And then usually, if we're getting dissed, you know, out of anybody in this room, it's usually Robin.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
That's cool, though. But I'm saying that's what happens.
But you guys are here to say you are big recording artists. You are a major force. You're selling $6 million a year just in merchandise, and your records are doing well.
We just don't want to be like, we know we'll never be invited to give away an award at MTV.
Why won't MTV get behind you guys still? You've proven yourself.
Do you guys make videos?
Yeah.
We don't make that money. That's why we're not part of the corporate ball that makes, like, the industry money.
Nobody at MTV has anything to do with our success. Nobody at radio except, you know, you or us getting arrested. Being on TV that way, you know what I'm saying?
How do you explain?
But aside of all the controversy, like, we don't have any hits.
How do you explain that at least 40 or 60 people with full clown makeup were downstairs today early in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, waiting for you, and
this
Paul McCartney...
This is how I explain it. I'll tell you exactly how I explain it. Because when you're at a red light, and you're listening to a song that's on, like, a radio station, and you're feeling it and feeling personal to it, and then all of a sudden a car pulls up next to you, and some other kid's got the same song on, because he's listening to the same station, and you're just like, you don't feel as close to that music. But if you're into ICP, you gotta look for it to find it. It's yours.
And you own it.
And
no radio station has
what you're listening to. Nobody's familiar with any of our songs. There is nobody that's like, I like some ICP stuff, but the rest sucks. Because we don't have one hit. Nobody's waiting for
people a song buy your albums concert. And listen to the entire album.
Right. Exactly. Chances are you're not going to be in your car listening to ICP, and somebody's not going to pull up next to you bumping that same song.
Were you offended by the fact that Insane Clown Posse, your band, was voted the worst band ever by Blender Magazine? Come on, that's got to hurt.
Yeah, man. I love that.
At least they put you down below Celine Dion.
Right.
Like Kenny G. I don't give a rat's ass about Kenny G, but that isn't that an insult?
Imagine if we'd have been number 19 or 27.
Yeah, just
that would really suck.
But wait,
we're number one or something, you know?
You must have been offended by that.
We were number one. That means we're the most different, outrageous.
Wait, I read a statement by you that said, how could Blender Magazine call us the worst band ever? When they said our last album, they gave it 3 stars.
Yeah, that's true.
So you had to be offended by that. They're not being fair, are they?
It's just whoever writes the article, you know?
If you look at the article, though, they got, like, Nelson on there. And when, you know, you look back at Nelson and see those two rock and roll wolves with the long bleach hair, that was funny.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
But are you in the same category?
No, because we're here for good. And we've proven that. It's been 10 years now.
If you had the guy from Blender Magazine on the phone right now, what would you say to him?
Man, I got to be honest with you. I'm not going to front. We've been claiming to be the world's most hated band for 3 years.
Rob.
Yeah.
Rob Tannenbaum is the senior editor of Blender Magazine.
What's up, homie?
Hey, how you guys doing?
They're not saying... They're saying you're the worst band musically in the history of music.
Well, the whole thing is...
That's what they're saying.
Well, here goes the thing. This Rob guy on the phone right now, he's probably a flop musician that was in a band that didn't make it.
So Rob, is that true, what Shaggy 2 Dope says?
Well, you know, the selection of them as the as Blender Magazine's worst band ever really was a collective decision, so it's got nothing to do with my musical accomplishments or lack of.
In other words,
So in other words, is Shaggy 2 Dope correct? Were you in a band?
Yes, I was.
Yes. All music critics always were in a band.
Hey, what's his name, Rob?
Rob.
Rob is looking at us sitting on a Howard Stern show in clown paint. You know what I'm saying?
What band were you
with? He can't stand it.
Are you jealous in a way, Rob? Seriously, now that's a good point the band is making.
There's only one thing that I'm jealous of, and that's their money.
But in all seriousness, they get to go up on stage and perform. They have girls.
They do all the stuff we dreamt of doing.
We do what we want to do. We rock shows. Rock shows.
Rob, was it your dream at one point to rock shows?
No.
What was your dream? What was your band?
My band was called White Courtesy Telephone, and the only reason that I was ever in a band was to write about the experience.
Wait, you were in WCT?
Exactly.
I didn't know that.
World famous.
Oh, much respect.
So, Rob, what about that? I applaud the list because you put the Doors on there. I think the Doors are horrible, and I get more mail about that every time I say it. But
they have their followers.
The Doors
are crushingly overrated, and in fact, they ruin rock and roll for years.
Well, the thing is, they're legendary, though. You know what I'm saying? So we feel honored being the number one hated, actually number one.
We're worse than the Doors. Yeah,
when was the last
album.
Time anyone mentioned Insane Clown Posse in the same breath as the Doors and Mick Jagger?
Right, so that's the first time the boys have been on any list with anybody of that prominence.
See, that's the thing. That's why you're not hearing complaints out of us about it.
My question
to you, Rob, and your whole committee, or whoever made the decision, is how can, just answer this, how can 2,000 people, real people, regular people, pack into a venue, sing every lyric, and have the best time of their life? I mean, a great show worth every penny to them. They love it. They had a great time. There's not one fight between 2,000 people. And then, as they file out and go home, how can you just say, well, they suck? Who are you or that committee to say something sucks? I don't like Waylon Jennings, but if he's putting 13,000 people in some country bunking bar, I don't think that sucks. I got mad respect for him. I'm like, okay, he's doing his thing. How can you just say, or your committee? And who are you talking about? According to what? cool people? According to radio and MTV statistics, we never wanted to be part of that. How do we suck? How can that be when all of these people are having such a good time and we're doing such a good thing, but we suck apparently? Who the hell are you or your committee to say when something sucks?
How do you respond to that, Brian?
When something as successful as us suck, when you and the water transfer factory or whatever the hell your brand was called fell off the map years ago, and everybody else in your stupid committee, everybody else in your committee probably fell off too. They were all part of Pig Face and all these other stupid no-name bands that fell off. How can you possibly say we suck when we're as successful? Other words, we're making somebody happy.
How do you respond to that, Rob? Yeah.
I have a bad feeling that this is going to ruin my group's chances of opening for Insane Clown Posse. I think we just blew it.
Only thing you can open is your butt cheek so I can kick you in the ass, brother.
You can kick me in the ass. It's not going to make your music any better.
Okay. Now, if we're the worst.
What were the criteria, Rob, to pick ICP as the worst band? In other words.
Howard, hold on a second, because I want to answer that question. You said that there are 2,000 people who come to Insane Clown Posse shows?
Yeah.
Well, you could also find 2,000 people who drink their own urine and like it, but that doesn't mean I want to try it out.
All right. Yeah, but it's our music.
But they are attracting people, not drinking urine.
What the hell kind of point was that?
I know how that kind of shows he goes to.
They're not paying $4 to drink their own urine. It's music they're coming to hear.
Rob's going to pee conventions or something.
I challenge Rob to find 2,000 people, by the way, who like to drink their own urine.
In one room.
Yeah.
Maybe 5.
Artie's obviously never been on the internet.
You're right.
What is it, Baba Booey?
Not at any porn sites like you, brother. What are you talking about? What is the point?
You know what? I wanted to ask Rob, because I thought the biggest insult on the list, aside from saying they're the worst band, was how do you say that Air Supply is a better band than ICP?
Really?
Well, he's willing to say it. But what is the criteria?
All musical taste is subjective. Right. And the thing is this. There are people on that list. There are people on Blender's list of the 50 worst bands that Insane Clown Posse agrees with. Everybody thinks that there are some people who should be on the list, and some people who shouldn't have been on the list.
Hey, I thank you guys for putting
Clown Posse are on the list.
Well, come on. I mean, it's still a big insult, and the boys are putting a good spin on it, but the fact of the matter is,
wait, what is
the criteria for them being the worst band in the history of music?
It wasn't an easy decision, Howard. I'm not going to pretend like it was.
Right. Somehow David Hasselhoff were they up against?
It was David Hasselhoff on the list.
Well,
David Hasselhoff rocks, man.
We
a lot better than we do, obviously.
You should see the mosh pit at his shows, man. It's off the hook.
Howard, we could have filled the list with easy choices and, you know, shot ducks in a barrel. But it's too easy to just put in 50 soft rock bands or 50 mellow singers. You know, we didn't put Olivia Newton-John.
All right, so maybe they're not.
Why are they the worst?
So maybe they're not the worst. Target, maybe they're not the worst. Maybe it's sort of.
Why wasn't the Tunnel Water people on the list? Obviously, we got sucked for something we do. Why weren't you guys on the damn list? You never sold a record in your life.
I argued to put my own band
on
the list.
I'm sure you did.
It makes you feel better. Vanilla Ice beat you guys out. He's better than you.
Check this out. You know what I feel about that list? And I honestly believe it. I would have really been hurt had we not been number one.
You guys are flattered, right?
Say that, but I don't think they are.
No,
they would like to be honored for their music.
They
don't want to be on the list at all unless they're number one.
We've been saying we're the most hated band. That only tells me we're the most outrageous, different, unique thing there is.
All right,
I'm the most player hated.
We're the most unusual to the mainstream, to the public. We're the most outrageous thing. When you read the little thing what they wrote about us, trying to get some whatever they said.
Rob, thank you for joining us. He's the senior editor of Blender Magazine, Rob Tannenbaum. And thank you for explaining the list.
All right, thanks, Howard.
All right, there you go, Rob Tannenbaum. Eric, you're on the air with ICP. And St. Cloud Posse's book, ICP Behind the Paint, is available at FYE stores nationwide.
And what kind of revelations do we have?
You know what? I just can say this. I hope we suck this bad for another 10 years.
Yeah, right. You want to keep going.
I hope to God we can continue sucking.
You want to suck just like this.
Just like this and do it again for another 10 years. That'll be the bomb.
Yeah, go ahead. You're on the air. Jason, you want to say something? Now's your chance. Well, I guess Jason's gone.
Jason fell asleep.
Yeah, let's go to Larissa. Yes, Larissa.
Hi. Hello?
Yes.
Hello. Hey. I just want to show some clown love. You guys never get any love on here.
Man, you know what, though? It seems like more and more we are.
Yeah, it seems like people are liking them. Yes. YZ, go ahead.
Oh, Howard, it's YZ 12 is on the Wigger Show.
Yes.
You remember me?
No.
No.
Okay, against the Axis a while back. I just want to say I'm a fan of ICP.
Well, there you go.
You guys mad love, and you have no idea what these guys got musically unless you see them live. I've seen them at Woodstock one time. I heard them do F the World, and it changed my whole entire mind.
Hell
I went
yeah,
to see them at
yeah.
Birchill in Jersey, playing with Mars like 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
One of the best damn shows I've ever seen in my life.
See, there you go. In fact, I was impressed by the amount of fans that were outside the studio today. Tell me some of the things specifically that I can buy on your website. Like, if I want to, if I'm a huge ICP fan, what can I get?
Jerseys, lunchboxes, movies, action figures,
comic books.
Movie?
Yeah, we got a movie.
Okay.
Okay, we also run our own wrestling promotion. We put DVDs out about 3 a year.
So $6 million a year in just merchandise.
But it's more
you
than
guys are
we run
millionaire.
A whole record company. We got groups on tour right now that are out touring right now and filling houses. That you know, we're starting careers off. We're showing a whole way.
So you laugh at all of this.
Without the regular, you know,
going
MTV
through the regular channel.
We'll still be successful, yes, man. It might not be looked at and respected by everybody at first. That's because it's new. But that's why they won't play our video. That's why they won't talk about us, because they have nothing to do with this.
Right.
Talking about MTV.
Right.
That Rob guy should come down here and talk to those kids down in the lobby. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Tell them we suck.
Right,
you know what I mean? I mean, it's good to them, so how could they, what are they, just wrong people?
Yes, Mike, go ahead.
What is he saying?
Howard, what's up, my hook-nosed Jew bastard? Listen,
thank you.
The only thing that sucks about these guys is their attitude and the fact that they hide behind their makeup.
Will you ever take off the makeup? Will you ever come
who
out?
Who are you two guys?
Who are you guys? How do I even know it's the same two guys?
Just say this about our
Smothers Brothers.
That's your man, Adam Sandler. I promise paint and I turn into Shaggy.
Will you ever come out from like Kiss out of the makeup for years and then took it off?
You know, I don't know. We got no plans.
There's
for
super
that.
Photos of us without makeup in that book.
All over
you
the internet.
Oh yeah,
book. There is.
Yeah.
So I would buy the book just to see that. I want to see what the hell you guys look like.
I mean, we used to like never take pictures with people or not. Without makeup on, right. I were just like, whatever.
Because
you know
people
what
got pictures
you gotta live
in
your
their
life.
Watch. People got pictures in a necklace, cameras. You know, it's pointless trying to
get you walking out of Wendy's. Just like, look.
So you try to hide your face because it would be fun to always be anonymous, but now people, because they have so many cameras, they do discover you and
oh,
they take
time.
Your. Yeah, it's become
now,
a thing.
What are they like at home? I mean, what's the private life like?
Maybe girls at this point, like a steady girlfriend?
Hey, I'm a single man, and I see, when I used to come on a show, I was fronting. I had a woman at home.
Oh, is that right?
See, I wasn't faithful, but I had a woman at home that was...
Did you get a divorce?
No, I never was married or
right.
nothing.
Right.
But I happen to be a single man. I might be able to meet some bitch in Hollywood and take her home now. You know what I mean?
Right.
I could do anything.
And what about you, Shaggy?
I got a fiance.
Oh, is
fiance?
That right?
I'm a family man.
Really?
That's right.
When did this happen?
I don't know.
Where did you take her to propose? I mean, this is very romantic.
How did that come
she's
down?
Right in the living room at the house.
Without the makeup on or with it?
No, I made sure I put it on for her. I got up in my bathroom and put it on.
She must be a hot chick. I mean, you can get any girl you want being a super famous rock star.
She looks good, man.
Yeah, right. And did you knock her up? Is that the problem?
No, she's cool.
Yeah. When did you meet her? I mean, before all the success or...
A couple years ago.
Yeah?
He had to be successful first. He wasn't going to be getting
I couldn't get a girl that caliber being a scrub.
Exactly.
Just to say
scrub.
What that dude said that called, just so you know.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
here's the new book. Let me see what you look
all
like.
Right.
God damn, I would have recognized you, too.
I was shocked that I recognized Violent J without his makeup, but that is.
And I sure as hell wouldn't recognize Shaggy, too, though.
Really?
No.
You must have been really shocked, because that wasn't me.
Let me see some of these people been waiting all morning for
but
you.
Listen, I just got to say this. The reason why people think we got a bad attitude is because simply, man, we're the people's people. Like, we're not Hollywood. Like when I came out last time and told you about when Pam Anderson asked me out. No, I never hit it. I never went out with her. But I'm a regular dude, man. I'm a dude
well,
from Detroit.
Well, come on.
That's
if you're making
deal.
$6 million a year, you're hardly regular.
Oh, but we are, though. That's what makes us
you'd
fresh.
Be surprised.
We're not,
you're not living in a trailer.
Man, you'd be surprised how quick we run through that money.
You know, is that right?
Stupid stuff, yeah.
All right, well, that's good to hear. All right, let's...
makeup's free, Howard?
By the way, this girl's pretty attractive. I didn't
hell
expect
yeah.
you guys had attractive fans like this.
I'd hit it.
Oh, look at that.
Damn right you'd hit that. What's your name, honey?
My name's Jody.
Jody, you're a big ICP fan, huh?
Yeah.
You go to all the shows?
Lately, yes.
You got a nice body, nice face. How old a woman are you?
Thank you. 28.
28 years old.
And see, who now, turned would you on to
would
ICP?
You notice her without her makeup on?
Oh, yeah, I sure would. You got a nice kick-ass body, I'll tell you that.
Thank you.
Now, would you bang ICP if they asked?
Oh, my gosh.
Her man's standing right there.
Oh, is that her man? Is that your man?
Would I don't want to go downstairs and get
I'm gonna ask you that because we got a limo outside, and I'll call her out on it as soon as we're off.
Like, that's a good-looking girl.
I think the guy would bang.
Do you mind if Insane Clown Posse had sex with your girlfriend?
No, not at all, dude.
All
really?
Right.
I mean, you know,
see,
we're
that's
brothers.
Rock star.
We're family.
Your family.
Family.
You consider yourself part
dude,
of the
action. The gathering they gave us was the bomb.
Man,
that was mine.
Man, it was the gathering is a once-a-year convention of all the juggalos around the world.
How many people show up to something? Year. How many people show up to that?
I think it was like,
what? 5,000 this year, right?
Yeah,
yeah, 5, they like restricted it. The city restricted it, but next year we're getting like up to like 8,000.
It was in a campground 3 days.
Well, there you go, Rob.
Now, let me ask you something. Did you guys meet at one of these gatherings?
No.
No, we've been together about 11 years.
Oh, okay.
Are you the only chick at the gathering? I mean, I figured you'd probably get like gang-banged by 5,000 guys.
No, there's lots of girls, man.
A lot of hot chicks like you?
Yeah.
You can watch them naked.
There's like families there, you know, like
kids,
really?
Babies and stuff. It's crazy.
They have
babies out
little
there,
babies yeah.
In the lake, just chilling out. You know,
they have mud wrestling. The
honey, what's your story? You've got a job?
No, I don't work.
That's what I figured.
I'm on a JuggleLet'sGoOnWicked.com.
How do you? What do you mean JuggleLet's?
JuggleLet'sGoOnWicked.com.
What's that mean?
Like Girls Gone Wild.
Yeah. Uh-huh. But it's JuggleLet'sGoOnWicked.
Do you sell that tape?
.com.
No.
We're putting out a DVD in about another month. We'll have her and several other sexy Juggalettes.
What do? You get naked on there?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Fago
I want to
shower.
See. No kidding.
Naked Fago showers. I'll send you a copy if you give me your address, buddy.
You know the address.
Do have on clown makeup in the...
Yes.
I see.
See, you got to understand something, man. Like what we do, it's kind of like... I don't want to compare it to Christian rock, but, like, I don't know nothing about that whole world. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah. You got to be into that world to understand what it's about, you know?
Right.
It's the same thing with our world. It's
but
like
the dark side.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? It's the exact opposite of Christian rock.
So,
you know
honey,
what I'm saying?
Are you doing porno?
No.
No. It's just you get on there, and what do? You flash?
It's mostly just still pictures, and there is some video of, like, Fago showers, girls pouring Fago on themselves. Fago is soda that they made very popular.
Yeah. Is that what you do for a living, though? You just...
No, I don't get paid for that.
How do you make any money?
I'm a trash man.
Oh, you supporting her?
Yeah.
Nice. Sharing the wealth.
Sugar daddy.
Nice. Sugar daddy. I didn't know that.
She takes care of me as I
do. Damn right she does.
Hey, can I give a shout out to the Juggalos and Juggalettes stuck downstairs that couldn't make it up?
All right, brother. Go ahead, real quick.
Shout out to them, bro.
Yeah.
All right. Well, listen, Insane Clown Posse is here for a reason. The new book, ICP Behind the Pain, is available at FYE stores nationwide. And ICP's Wicked Wonka Tour kicks off September 17th in Cleveland.
Yeah.
For more information, go to InsaneClownPosse.com.
And that's with Bone Thugs and Harmony. That's with Cottonmouth Kings. Yeah.
Wow.
That's
whoa.
With Tech N9ne.
Wait a second. We're getting flashed. Yeah, honey, show us those boobs, will you? Give us a break. Wow.
Whoa. Well, let's see those Juggalos.
This is nice.
Man.
Yeah.
These guys are rock stars.
And Lodi, you guys big fans too, huh?
Absolutely, Howard.
Yeah. How do you? What do you guys do for a living?
Excuse me?
What do you do for a living?
Home Depot.
You work at Home Depot?
Yeah.
Oh, no wonder I can't get it.
They don't bust my balls either. They know I'm down.
They do?
Yeah.
They don't bust your ass about the tattoos?
Nah, luckily. They don't give me any grief.
Yeah. Look at that, man. That see right there, man. That right there. Man.
What? What did you just say?
Look at all them tattoos, man. You know what I'm saying? How can you react to that? That just puts me in shock.
Yeah, Rob.
Hey, we knew what you were saying.
I'm a stay-at-home dad.
What do you want to say there, brother?
I'd just like to say, Howard, that I'm a stay-at-home father, and if I could give a quick shout-out to my 3-week-old daughter, Mackenzie Sierra Savage, I love you, baby.
And you're holding up the Insane Clown Posse book, sir.
What does his wife do to support him?
Yeah, absolutely. Go get it. It's great.
You stay at home and raise the kids. What's your wife doing?
Yeah, she's in college right now full-time and works full-time. I love you, too,
Amanda. You know what, though? All of these juggalos, in a couple of years, they're going to be the ones running the country. They're going to be the ones programming the radio.
Every day scrubs.
And you're going to see us rolling around legendary.
there's the plan. Insane Clown Posse. Always good to get the update from you guys. I can
man,
see you're thriving.
Thank you again, man.
And thank you to the ICP fans. We'll be back right
thank
after
you
these
for
words.
Having us.
All right, baby. And thanks for flashing us those jugs. Very nice. Yeah. We'll be back right
after that. People often wonder how two serial killers from Detroit that call themselves the Insane Clown Posse became so rich and famous. Now see here, Howard Stern used to live and work radio in Detroit before he became a New York City big shot. Howard and the clowns go way back. I'm 5'10", I'm certified coach. Straight millionaire, 25 years old. Dropped out of school to watch Prices Right, and I strangle people at night. Look, everybody knows I'm a killer. Twisted murderer, sick drug dealer, or whatever. I never tried to hide the fact, it's true, but Howard Stern's a killer too.
95 X.
Ladies and gentlemen,
hey now.
Please welcome Howard Stern.
On our phone line, I just want to welcome Shaggy 2 Dope, who is one half of Insane Clown Posse, who was supposed to be booked on the show a couple of weeks ago, Insane Clown Posse, but Shaggy got his collarbone, no, got his neck broken.
So what you're saying is that they had to cancel the appearance because of his mishap?
Yes. Shaggy.
Yo, what's up, man?
How you feeling? Listen, you're a friend of the show. I was just concerned about you. That's the only reason for this call, but what happened?
Yo, I be honest, I don't really know, man. I'm hanging in, you know. I just got a piece of metal stuck in my discs or neck or something like that.
What happened, though? Because
how did a piece of metal get in your neck?
You are not a professional.
Well, surgeons, of course.
Yeah, you're not a professional wrestler.
Well, we're supposed to be, but not really.
Right. Where did you wrestle?
Our own thing. It's called JCW, Juggalo Champion Ship, I'll say, wrestling.
Oh, so you have your own wrestling thing?
Well, to be honest, I'm not even sure it's from wrestling. You know, I can't pinpoint exactly where it happened. I mean, I know where it happened, but I don't know how it happened. Because I've had the same problem for a couple of years now.
Oh, I heard that it was that you got dropped doing a wrestling.
No, it could be. It could be doing that, or it could be stage dive. I'm not sure.
So what happened? You started feeling pain in your neck?
Well, I've had the same, like, I guess you could say problem for a couple of years now. You know what I'm saying? I think it's sort of over the edge. You know, what was the C5, I think, and C6 discs were shattered in my neck or something like that.
Oh, I see. I thought that he...
Yeah, he was wrestling and somebody did a move on him and he broke his neck.
No, I it could have been.
All right, so you're all right then.
But I'm not really sure because it took a couple of days after that to realize that, you know, one side of my body went numb. My left side went numb, and all of a sudden, who knows, you know, finally my wife made me go to the doctors, and they were like, what are you, crazy? You know, what are you even walking for, you stupid? I'm just like, I didn't know it was that bad, you know?
You said your wife made you go?
Yeah.
When did that happen?
Probably about a month after I shattered my discs.
You got married?
Oh, when did that happen?
Yeah.
May 7th, man.
Yeah, the other tragedy.
Yeah. That horrible accident.
That was way better than breaking my neck. I'll give it that one.
All right.
May 7th, you got married.
All right, so there's no real story here other than you're going to be okay.
Yeah, hopefully. You know what I'm saying? Because I was supposed to, like, sit at home for, like, 3 months, but, you know, the show must go on, so I got to go back on the road on October 1st.
And can you walk?
Oh, yeah, I can walk now. You know, I was hemmed up in the hospital for a couple of days, but yeah, everything's cool now. I mean, you know, I can't, like, lift anything, like, beyond my shoe and put it on my foot right now. But so hopefully by October 1st, I'll be good enough to be going back on the road and all that.
Now, how are you
going
to go on the road if you can't even lift anything? I mean, you guys do a whole theatrical thing.
I can still lift cars, man.
Yeah?
It's all good.
All right. I was just checking up on you, Shaggy.
That's cool, man. That's cool. I appreciate that. But, yeah, everything's going all right, you know? I mean, you know, I'm just, like, sitting around the house doing my thing, you know.
Couldn't he do something dangerous to his neck if he goes out on the road?
Well, yeah, they told him he's, you know, he wouldn't even be completely healed in
a. No, I'll be 100% in 3 months. You know, it'll be a month since I got the surgery once I go out. You know, I just got to calm down. I can't be doing, like, no stage diving. Right. Nothing crazy like that, you know.
You know, once you get out there.
You know, the adrenaline hits, but, you know, we just came out with a record a week and a half ago, you know, so it's like you got a tour off of, you know.
Right.
It's like, just like, you know, if you work at a factory and you cut your finger off, you eventually got to go back to work, you know?
Right. Well, listen, say hi to Violent J for me. I hope everything's all right.
Oh, man, it's 4 in the morning.
Yeah.
Yeah. Something like that. I'm going to talk to him probably about 2 hours. So let's talk, man.
All right, good. All right, brother.
All right, man.
All right, come see us soon.
No doubt, man. As soon as I can actually fly, I'll be out there, and I'm going to co-host your show for like a week straight.
Beautiful.
There you go.
Shaggy Two Dope. Are you wearing the clown makeup right now, or are you free of that?
Oh, of course, man. I'm sleeping. I always wear it when I'm sleeping.
I heard when they operated on him, he was in full clown makeup.
Yep.
Yeah. All right. Take care, Shaggy.
Actually, I was wearing fluorescence, so like, you know, the operation lights made my face glow, so it was all good.
All right, Shaggy. Later.
All right, man.
Right. Shaggy Two Dope. The new album is Hell's Pit, available in stores now.
Who does he think he was talking to? Jimmy Kimmel? He wants to co-host the show for a week?
Yeah. I thought I was Mike Douglas. Well, some of my favorite guests are the Insane Clown Posse. You haven't seen the boys in a while. I believe they broke up for a while. They are back together again. One of the most successful musicians, musical groups out there, Insane Clown Posse.
Why can't they stay together? Everybody's against them. You'd think they'd hold it together.
It's sad, isn't it? You'd think they would hold it together. I mean, these guys have been fighting the good fight. There they are. Two huge successes in the music industry. Everyone in the music industry was against them.
Always.
Always. And the two of them rose to become one of the biggest musical acts on the planet.
Hey, man, you got comfortable couches now.
You're goddamn right we do.
Not bad breakers.
So good to see you boys. You beat the odds. The two of you went up against the entire industry.
That's right. Still a lot.
And why would you break up when it was the two of you battling the world?
Brother. It's all rumors, speculation,
that's
lies.
The craziest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Insane Clown Posse did break up.
No.
It's
purely speculation. Never really happened.
What about the solo project?
It was a solo project. The
Shaggy 2 Dope.
Vada J's had solo projects before.
When you're talking about mapping out our entire career, you got to do things to make things different, you know. Sometimes, I mean, he went out on his own solo tour.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Shaggy 2 Dope went off on his own solo tour. I heard Shaggy
started the rumors, huh?
Shaggy, I heard you were having some trouble and you had to go to rehab. Is that true?
Yeah, rehab's great, man.
You love rehab. Why is rehab so great for you? Shaggy 2 Dope.
Because the chicks are easy there. You know, you come with a pocket full of rocks, forget about it. You know what I'm saying?
Did you get laid in
rehab?
Nah, I'm married. Plus, they'll kick you out, man. You can't fuck that.
No?
No.
No. Well, let me understand something because it's confusing to me. Violent J, when Shaggy went into rehab, it was rumored you couldn't handle it. It was too much for you. And be honest now, didn't that cause a rift between you two guys?
There was never a rift between us, but there was a lull there where we didn't tour and we didn't make any records.
3 years?
Nah.
Yeah. 3 years.
I mean, there was like parts, you know what I'm saying, like where I fucked up a lot of opportunities because, you know,
I was going to say, was the drug habit, whatever
it was just
causing
alcohol.
Problems in his business?
Yeah, just
no alcohol. Heroin, no cocaine?
No, come on. No, I had a crack. I ain't already, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right. No one's dead. Come on,
I got laid in rehab.
Nobody's as messed up as
I'm Indian. I just stuck with the fire water, my friend.
Right.
But now I'm hardcore. Now I'm like Motley Crue style. I like mainstream O'Doul's, so it's all good.
No, but wait a second. The two of you were not talking for a while.
No, that's never, ever, ever been the truth.
What happened?
This is my brother. This is no
but
doubt.
You couldn't take it. You had to take a break.
Could nobody
didn't
take it? I
no, we
drunk.
Never.
I'm saying.
What was it?
There was never ever any problem with between us ever. That's totally, you know, that I don't know where that's
did
from.
Did you have to tell him he had a problem and that he should get some help?
Everybody I knew did. My wife, all my homies. It was like time, you know, to clean up.
Did you do an intervention? Was there an intervention?
We had our own little,
like soprano style
get-togethers, you know what I'm saying?
Who was there? Who is it? When someone as important as the Insane Clown Posse has a problem, you guys are a mega-million-dollar industry.
See, what you gotta understand that, like everybody that is Psychopathic Records are lifelong homies, you know
right.
what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So just my homies and my wife and my family and shit, you know?
Right.
So we were there for him. You know, it was never a case where
we didn't talk
or nothing like that. But here goes the hook, though, because I've been to two of them boys, and, like, the first time I went, it was, like, a 2-week little ditty in, like, this place in Ohio.
Yes.
I forget the name of it, but, like,
with off the street crackheads, you know what I'm saying? My roommate was like a little old crackhead guy, you know what I'm saying? I thought it was awesome, you know what I'm saying? So I never marinated with a real crackhead like that before, you know, a roomie.
Right.
I mean, I've, you know, seen him a million times, you know what I'm saying?
Did that rehab help you? No.
No, because it was like a lockdown hospital, you know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
But then I went to this place up in Amsterdam, New York, and that place is a bomb.
That's how much were you drinking to cause this intervention? I didn't see that you were drunk.
Fifths
a day.
No, but it snowballed. When we'd come on the show, I wouldn't be drinking.
Right.
But I just like just start slow, you know what I'm saying, waking up to kill the hangover, you know.
Do you have a personality change? Is that what happens, Violent J, to him? Does he have a personality change when he drinks?
It was a case of being left over drunk from the night before.
I see. Insane Clown Posse, though, is an intimate situation. It's the two of you together. You can't be talking to a guy that is hungover in a big mess. Is that what it is?
When it comes down to the actual moment where it comes time for us to flex our multitude of talents,
mm-hmm.
and the liquor is in the way, that was the only time it became an issue.
Yeah.
Is when we step into the studio or you know, that's where we really shine. Or when we step, you know, to do
on
something.
Stage.
Yeah.
And you were getting into fights with people, was that part of
I still get into fights.
Oh, you still
but not only
that's problem, a sober thing though.
You're right. The only problem with that now is I remember the fights, you know.
You fight.
And now I can't tell the judge. I don't know what happened, I don't remember. Because now I remember, so I can't lie to the judge.
You fight with the audience, right? You fight with the people at the Insane Clown Posse show. Sometimes.
No, I mean, hey, once in a while, somebody will jump up with their ass hanging out. You know, you got
anybody with a mouth on them. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
He's gonna, you know?
You're not afraid of anyone. Insane Clown Posse stands up to everybody.
Sure.
And what was your drink of choice?
Vodka.
Vodka.
Yeah.
All right.
And you would drink
hardcore.
Just drink it straight down?
Yeah, rock good.
Do you miss it now?
Nah, fuck no.
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 How long have you been
sober? Year and a half.
Year and a half.
Wow.
Year and a half.
And now are you back in love with your wife? Is she in love with you?
I always have been.
You've always been in love with her.
Yeah.
And you're a better man.
If I took a sip, she'd divorce me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Is he an easy
guy? And if I took a sip, me and him, well, I'd be on the floor with him stomping my ass. You know what I'm saying? Put it this way. All right. The whole key to getting sober, Arby, is
Arby.
I look like I eat roast beef.
No, seriously though, the whole key is a strong support team. If you got like homies that are down by law with you like that,
right.
And you go home and your wife is down by law with you like that, you ain't gonna fuck around. You know what I'm saying? But if you come out of rehab, you start hanging out with your drunk ass friends. You know what I'm saying? They don't give a fuck if you're drinking again. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So that's the key. You know.
So Arby. You've got to.
Well, you guys are my homies.
Down with you
and George.
Yeah, but we didn't even
Robin
know Artie was on heroin. We didn't know he was on heroin.
No, he never shares.
He never tells us.
Well, what am I going to do? Come in here and say, God, guys, I got some great heroin.
Well, that's what happens. You can't see tracks on the inside of your eyelids.
How do you fucking start heroin, though? I mean, how do you? What do you say?
Try this.
I'm not cutting nobody down.
Dude, I'm not the one with the makeup on my face.
Yeah, but you got a little mustard chiller.
Now, you never got tempted by any of that, like hardcore?
Come on, I mean, okay.
Good for you, that's actually good.
Well, what kind of day are you having when you're like, well, let me try this heroin. Maybe I'll like it and
maybe
be fucking hooked on it forever. You know what I mean?
I'll never forget the first day I did it, and I was having one of those days. I was it was in Kansas City, in a hotel, man.
Wait. I seen this crackhead yesterday? Yeah. Man, I'm going to hit that pipe, boy.
Yeah. I mean, when you're drinking, you know, that's something you get into and I don't know.
Yeah, I'll tell
you
who's social thing. Can drink and not have their lives ruined.
Right. I'll tell you who's fresh, though.
She has admitted to it.
Yeah.
She has?
Yeah.
Right, I just hit the dump button. I didn't know she admitted to it.
Oh, yeah, that's full speculation.
Right,
I didn't know that.
That's awesome.
The English chick? The princess?
No, the Black Eyed Peas.
Black Eyed Peas.
Oh, I thought you were going to talk about Ferguson Jenkins, the Cubs pitcher.
That was my call. The crackhead peas.
Now, you look at the Black Eyed Peas for a minute, all right? Now, this is Fergie with her lovely lady lumps and everything. This is a band that gets nothing but respect. I mean, top of the line respect, right? And she's fucking addicted.
Are you guys getting, she's not addicted anymore, is she?
No, she's cleaned herself up.
As of what, last week? Give her a month.
Come on, Chris.
Come on, give everyone a break. Come on, let's be fair.
We'll know in 3 months. We'll look at her grill.
when her
teeth look like a half-eaten quarter.
I heard something nice about you guys, which I was really kind of shocked. you know, you've been on this show, and you've been at war with Sharon Osbourne, who is Ozzy Osbourne's wife. And yet, when you heard she had cancer, you sent her flowers. Is that true?
With a note, yes, that said, don't go nowhere without paying us back the money you owe us. With a note that said, don't think about leaving without the fucking 50 G's you owe us,
no,
bitch.
No, it's cool. I sent her a bouquet of flowers, but I picked the petals off. For
no,
the,
we didn't, you know, we, no, we didn't send her shit.
Oh.
I mean, listen, when she was, hey, put it this way, when she was ill, when she was ill, we refrained from calling her a bitch and talking about her, but now that she's healthy again, fuck her. And another thing, what the fuck is going on? Wait a minute. If we had lost that bet, if we didn't sell 50,000 records on our next record, we'd never hear the fucking end of it.
Yeah.
But we've released, what, 3 albums, 4 albums since then? Each one of them did over $250,000. Where the fuck's our money? And another thing, we didn't say, give us the 50 grand. We said, give it to any fucking charity you want in our name.
Right.
Just pay the 50 grand.
She did.
She was the one
she gave it
that told us to stay here another day.
Right.
Remember?
Right.
We stayed another night so we could confront that bitch. If we stayed here, then she made the fucking challenge. She was the one that was like, you will never, what was that, 10 years ago, 9 years ago?
Right.
You won't be around, your next album won't even sell 50,000 copies,
and
is what
you
said.
And you bet her $50,000.
That's right.
My friend, I'll tell you
and
what.
Our next album after that went fucking almost platinum.
Right. It was a big album for
that. So where's the money?
I don't know.
It's in Ozzy Osbourne's veins. Hey, but check it out.
Right.
Now, that's what you call karma. See, pay up, bitch. That's why she caught the cancer.
Right.
Wow.
It's as simple as that. If we had, we'd have been like,
here you go. Now, check this out. Check this out. Have her give that money to some cancer kids.
There you go. She should, right?
Right. Do you guys have a lot of enemies? I mean, you really do speak your mind. I mean, I imagine this.
When we're right. In
you
a situation
right.
like that.
No doubt. You're right. You did prove all the critics wrong. You did.
Her is the only critic I give a fuck about because she's the one with the checkbook.
How many albums have you guys sold in total, would you say?
I don't know. You know,
it's hard to tell nowadays because people download and steal your shit.
And besides, it don't even matter. You could suck and sell 5 million records if you got the right push behind you.
You still warring with Eminem, or is that over?
That's over with. I mean, we don't.
You gotta feel bad for Eminem.
We haven't seen him.
You're not gonna see a collaboration with him.
Yeah, you ain't gonna see him.
But come on, that's like what, 10 years old now.
You know. As for Eminem, you know, there was a lot of real, genuine.
Hatred.
There.
Yeah.
But,
why?
I forget
why.
Well, yeah, because it all stems back from Detroit. But see, he's not around no more. I mean, he's not on the streets no more in Detroit, in Michigan.
Well, that's what I said. You got to feel bad for him. He's going through some really tough times.
But I'll tell you something about the
lake. He is.
What? Sure. Oh, he had to go into rehab because he had a sleeping pill problem.
A sleeping pill. Who has a sleeping pill problem?
Well, he was addicted to Ambien, isn't that correct?
Yeah, the little fucking butterflies.
I've been taking a pack of NyQuil a day for 15 fucking years. I have no plans of stopping.
Rehab for sleeping pills.
Fuck. All right, anyway, but
are you sure there were Quaaludes?
Quaaludes. Fuck yeah. If anybody has a Quaalude, let me sample one of them.
I'll try to shit out of a Quaalude. Who's got a Quaalude?
No one.
You're 70s or something.
I think you got one.
You guys know someone who gets loose.
I found a few Quaaludes. They are actually manufactured in Europe.
What are they, like volumes or something?
They're not as good as what they... But the Soapers and the 747s, they don't make them like they used to.
Listen to this, bro.
Yeah,
he loves those.
I never heard of the game.
Yeah, Howard did Ludes. You like Ludes.
I think I had a problem. There used to be 25 cents back in the day.
Maybe you should go to rehab with Eminem for the Quaaludes.
I didn't need any rehab.
Also, sleeping pills.
I just stopped. That was it.
Also,
it's pretty bad when you go to rehab for a Quaalude.
Also, also, he, you know, remarried his wife.
What the fuck?
Beep that off. I don't
know. I don't know about that.
Don't say that.
But,
go ahead.
Okay. But the thing that's really,
it wasn't rehab. It was a bar parking lot. Or maybe
really,
the urinal. Who knows?
Really bad that you really should feel sorry for him. You know, when they divorced the first time, they had a very difficult divorce, and he had to settle a lot of money on her. Now they're going through the same thing again.
Well, but why does he want that? I mean, it ain't my business. I don't want to restart any old feuds. But why does he want that lame-ass bitch? He could have any bitch he wants.
Right.
Why does he want that stale-ass fucking, I mean,
are you married now? What's going on with you?
I'm not married, but I do have a little son.
You do?
Yes.
Do you have a girlfriend?
And I have a girlfriend, and I have a daughter on the way.
Wow,
a daughter soon to be born in December.
Will you marry this woman that you're having
the
children with?
The mother of your children?
Or are you setting a bad example
Why you got to put a motherfucker on the spot like that?
Well, let's find out. Are you thinking of, I mean, two kids. Maybe it's time to give the kids legitimacy and...
what do we call those kids?
Some security
for
you.
Look, I never had a dad. You know what I'm saying? And I'm the shit.
What is it, 2000?
So I don't know nothing about the values of marriage. Or nothing like that. You can't tell me the importance of marriage. I had fucking four dads.
Does your four dads?
Yes. Yeah, so
you
I don't
four
need
dads. Yeah, your mom had four different men that she married?
Yes. During the time I grew up.
He's kind of like
so
Freddy Krueger.
I don't even understand the importance
like Freddy
of that. All I know.
Are you damaged as a result of that? I mean, you seem like a perfectly normal guy.
I'm off the fucking chain. There ain't nothing wrong with me.
What? I mean, seriously, when you
hey,
see
wait,
him,
man, we're Sulu.
Right there.
Oh,
and that's an extra benefit.
Yeah,
right there.
What's up? I'm used to dealing with alien life forms.
Hey, check it out, though. Hey, I seen your episode of Twilight Zone.
Sweet.
See, that's what kind of
Twilight Zone.
Real.
You saw Boom. That.
Yes. Yes. In the attic with the samurai swords. Yes.
Sweet shit right there, brother.
I was just telling my boys about that shit.
Right.
Sulu in the house somehow.
George, are you a fan of Insane Clown Posse?
Yeah, he was.
Very big.
I'm afraid I'm not familiar. Familiar with your work, but thank you for your compliment.
Well, that's fine. I was just playing. I didn't see your shit neither.
They're very defensive.
You never saw Twilight Zone.
No, I seen this shit, man. It's all right.
You were Star Trek.
That little Star Trek thing you did was cool.
Yeah, that was cool. I'm going to have to check out
your work, too.
You guys are Trekkies.
I had a Trekkie, but I'm more of a...
I ain't no fucking Trekkie.
You're not a Trekkie?
No, I respect
I like the old
them,
school ones. I like the old school Star Trek because you see the fishing string on all the aliens and shit. And Captain Kirk was the biggest pimp ever. That's why.
That's right.
Oh, he was a womanizer.
Fuck yeah. And he fucked aliens. That's what made him really frustrated.
They could be green. They can have
But he had sex. He had sex off. I mean, as William Shatner, he had sex with a lot of different women.
Oh, yeah.
And the best part
is. And he married quite a few of them.
Here goes a cool thing, though, because Star Trek was supposed to be in the future. Did he have like some kind of like hologram rubber, or is he just raw dogging these hoes?
He was raw dogging.
He's probably like mad crazy. We had bad kids
by this time.
You know, child support was good for his ass.
They had cured all the diseases.
Yes, you set your phaser on sterile.
Ozzy Osbourne is on the phone. Ozzy, what's going on with Sharon? How is her health? And also, what is this feud with Insane Clown Posse?
The booze bomb, of course. Because, first of all, like you said, I agree with you in Saint Crump, but I think Sharon's a fucking cunt, you know.
Right.
I was actually putting same, I was looking up if they would be able to come into Beverly's.
Tell him to call back when he wakes up.
But Ozzy is agreeing with you guys. I think Ozzy's kidding around. I know he loves his wife.
I'm the king of heavy metal, but I'm telling him to come and fuck my wife for me, man.
No fucking way, brother.
Ooh.
That's your fucking day.
Hey, can we have Sulu be a translator? Because I can't understand it.
Ozzy, you know, I love Sharon. I know the boys have a problem with Sharon, but does she owe them $50,000 and shouldn't she pay it?
Well, she only pays if they come into bed with us, all of them.
Oh, is Ozzy
what is going on?
He wants Insane Clown Posse in bed with you.
In bed with him?
With him and Sharon.
See, this is like we got to make it $50,000.
I think you need more than rehab, brother. You need therapy on top of it, because that's just crazy. Plus, she's like 80 or something like that. I'm straight.
All right. Well, thank you, Ozzy.
Thank you, Valerie.
All right.
But that, look, you know,
that wasn't really Ozzy.
Was that Ozzy Osbourne?
to reiterate. But yeah, as far as the Eminem thing goes, I just wanted to state something. Proof, the late Proof.
Yeah.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace. Did extend the hand of friendship to us, which was very fresh because, you know, we don't get a lot of respect in hip hop. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but
I know.
He extended the hand to us
right
back in Detroit. And we had a big D12 versus Psychopathic Records bowling match.
Oh.
Yep. Beautiful. I like to see people settle their differences with bowling. I'm a big fan of that.
I had to hate that between the Israelis and the Palestinians.
A big bowling match.
I actually had my own bowling ball.
It was an awesome game.
Was it hard for you growing
you like
up
to bowl
with four different dads? I mean, did you ever say to your mother, you sit down and go, Ma, what are you doing with all these different men, bringing them in the house?
My mom had a crazy tough life. You know what I'm saying? My mom was a janitor. You know what I'm saying? She had three kids. It's a long, fucked up dilemma with what she went through. But all you got to look at is the end product. You know what I'm saying?
Look at you. You're a self-made man. I mean, who would it be proud of you?
I'm a little concerned.
I mean, really. I mean,
you made
a big success.
So handsome guy. Come on.
In my family tree, I'm a hero.
Absolutely.
I put diapers on babies' asses, restriction-free, no problem. You know what I'm saying?
Boys, his babies.
Boys, what is going on now? I feel you're putting yourselves in danger with this wrestling. You're wrestling more and more. What is the big match coming up? You guys are going to wrestle?
We are on our way directly from this very impressive,
thank you,
brand new, highly technical, very impressive studio here.
Right.
We are on our way to Florida to join TNA Wrestling, Total Nonstop Action, where we will be shooting some TV shows, and we're no strangers to the squared circle, my friend.
I know.
The squared circle.
The two of you will wrestle who?
We're going to be getting into it with Team 3D.
The Dudley Boys.
The Dudley Boys.
You're
going to wrestle them?
I mean, we'll see what happens. See, you got to understand, I've broken my neck twice, shattered vertebrae. I got, dead body bones, tore my ACL.
How do you shatter your neck like that?
Wrestling.
I fell, 15 foot off. Actually, I broke it twice. The first time I broke it was wrestling. The second time was doing a show. The first time I fell off a steel cage match from the top and landed on a dude's knee on my face.
Ugh.
Head first and cracked my eye sockets, broke my nose, broke my neck.
Why continue doing it?
You're musicians, I thought.
Yeah, I thought you guys are musicians. What's going on?
We're like Andy Kaufman style. We got wrestling suits on underneath our outfits right now. But the second time actually was from doing a show. Our gathering at a Juggalo 2 years ago. I shattered three of my vertebrae because I was stupid. And I climbed up the lighting rig 40 feet high and did a backflip off it. And instead of when you crowd dive, you're supposed to land on your back or stump, but I head down, boom, shattered my shit. But I finished the show.
Will you ever appear without the clown makeup? I've never seen the two of you without clown makeup.
When do you get rid of the clown makeup? Yeah. Kiss, eventually they said, you know what?
I've been crying about an hour when we jump on this plane. It's hard getting through security. because it's liquid base, and you can't even bling
liquid. Is it hard to take off? Well, how do you get that off your face, seriously?
About 4 minutes work.
Really?
Yeah.
Comes right off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But to answer your first question about the wrestling, it's as simple as this. Childhood dreams. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When we were kids, liked wrestling.
Fuck yeah. That's what it all boils down to. If we can make our dream come true and actually do it instead of peeping it out, you know what I mean?
Right.
It's not our wrestling talent that's getting us to be able to wrestle on pay-per-view. It's our band name. But who wouldn't take that opportunity? You know what I'm saying? We'll take it all day. You know what I mean?
But are these guys going to take care of you, or are they going to try to kill you?
I look at it the other way around, Robin. You know what I mean? Because I'll kick somebody's ass. I don't know how to fake
a
punch.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'll fuck somebody up.
We know that wrestling, they call it quote-unquote fake, it still requires a lot of athleticism. You can get dropped on your head.
The thing about wrestling is a dude is only as good as the other guy makes him look.
Right.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So if somebody's punching you and you're looking at doing that shit, you know, you're making them look better. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And someone said now that you've taken on the religion of Scientology, that you guys are against Scientology.
No.
Violent J is a Scientologist?
Fuck yeah.
What is going on?
What are you talking about?
No.
What's
he
going
moved
on?
In with John Travolta.
Were you making out with John Travolta? No wonder I didn't recognize that guy in the tarmac with him.
I'm actually Tom Cruise. I just put Shaggy's makeup on.
Tell me what's going on. Is there something with you in Scientology? What is going on?
What?
I don't know.
What the hell is going on?
That's one of the freshest things I ever heard of. What is Scientology? Don't they like drive space saucers or something?
Yeah, I don't know.
You tell us. You guys are members.
I got a space saucer.
Would the fucking Scientologies actually take me?
I mean, I don't know. I'm sure they would. I'm sure they take anybody. Yeah. That's
don't
right.
Don't try to wear like a red.
Well, they can't have me. Fuck them. I'm not a Scientology.
Now, Insane Clown Posse's Hollow Wicked Clown Tour kicks off this Friday in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Now, talk about this tour for a second.
Massive.
What do you say massive? Will there be special effects? Will there be dancing girls? What's going to be on stage with you?
Well, we're going on tour with the Wolf Pack. We're going on tour with Boondocks, who's from Atlanta, Georgia. He's a new artist we signed. Right. He's like a fucking crazy hillbilly, like a scarecrow. The curtain opens up and he's stuck to the post, and he's got a cowboy hat on, and he's like a instead of coming from the streets and coming from the corners, he's coming from the crops, and he's coming from the barns. You know what I'm saying?
You know what's funny? As I look at you two guys, I'm thinking, you know, here you are. You could have lots of women. And here you got Shaggy, who is married. You got Violent J, who's now got kids and a girlfriend. You're not even getting laid on the road, are you?
You have no fucking clue to be saying that.
Are you getting blowjobs at least?
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about because, hey, I don't want to incriminate myself, but let's put two and two together here.
You put it together.
Right. You know what the fuck's going on with me.
What's the saying? It's not a crime if you don't get caught.
Right. Hey.
So you guys are still players. You still have things happening.
I play cards like a motherfucker.
You know what I mean?
I'll be Uno right now. I'll be anybody in this room at Uno.
What? Five Lola. What's up?
Sal and Richard are up to their old antics again. They'd like to join the Insane Clown Posse.
Why? What are they
doing? Well, they came in. Come on in, guys. They want to be part of the band.
Oh, boy.
I can't imagine what the
Sal
part
and Richard
of them
work
is
for me. What did they do now?
I hope they have the pants on.
They don't want to be naked. Oh, come on, you guys. What? Wait a second. Get some microphones on these
what
guys.
Part,
what are you doing now?
We want to be part of the Juggalos. We love the Insane Clown Posse.
Now, what have you done?
What's going on?
Well,
you know?
We've done something special to show our loyalty to you guys.
We're the Insane Cock Posse. We want to go on tour with you guys.
That's it.
Richard is Violent Gay.
Oh, what is that?
And I'm Shaggy too, Dick.
What the hell is that?
It looks like your dick might be going on tour with his butt. take a tour with
you guys.
Can
you guys autograph
one?
This is in tribute to you guys.
What do you think of that? These guys love showing their penises to other men.
They're finally quiet.
What do you guys think of that?
I think I'm contemplating running over there and sticking my foot up their ass. I'm seriously.
Do it, Violent. Do it.
Are you offended by this?
I'm seriously offended.
Right.
I feel the heat coming out of my shirt.
All right.
I'm very, very fucking uncomfortable.
Look in the mirror and give it a kiss, babe.
And,
do it, man. I'll join you.
And fucking. Something's about to break out right here in the studio if these two gentlemen don't leave. The closest thing is that megaphone, which is that perfect phone distance.
Why does that offend you so much?
Because he's waggling his fucking dick at me. What are you talking about?
Do you feel threatened by this?
What the fuck's going on?
Don't you have fans that put your makeup on and stuff, though? I mean, it's a tribute.
Fuck you. This is fucking creeping me out, brother.
Hey, man, what fans would commit like this? We're committed fans, man. Look what we did for you. We painted our packages for
your
you guys.
Dick's committed to his butt.
Violent J, were you ever accosted as a child? Did any of these men that your mother was married to, did they ever try to come on
what
to you?
What does accosted mean?
You know what I mean, sexually harassed by a man.
Can I ask I'm being sexually harassed right now.
Hey, seriously, if these guys don't leave in 5 seconds, I'm going to jump up and sock that faggot.
All right.
Well, wait
you
a second.
Have the cock alone.
Them boys are going to have to leave, dog.
Really, really.
I'm leaving. Get out of here.
No, that shit can't.
Wow, you chased him right out of the room. Tough man.
I should have tried that.
You chased him.
Shot sneak in. I'm gonna catch him right in the fucking chin.
That shit got my heart all beating. I felt like I feel like a fight was about to jump off.
Wait a minute. A naked guy is offensive to you?
Look, man.
Fuck yeah, yeah. A naked man with his dick painted like my face? What the fuck? That's offensive. Is that shocking? That would be offensive? That shit is crazy.
I've seen it all.
And on top of the head, baby meats. What's up with that?
Right. Their penises were small. You're right.
I mean, you know, hey, I got nothing against gay people, but flamers like that, man. Come on. When he's taking his dick on tour to his butt, there's something wrong with that.
Those guys love to walk in a room and be naked.
Well, you know, they do paint each other. You know, like, they don't paint themselves. They paint each other.
That was a fucking...
Yes. I was just wondering, just because I was here in the Insane Clown Posse Target, do they realize they're sitting next to, like... a gay activist?
Oh, we know.
No, hey, I'm totally cool with gay people.
George isn't getting his dick in front of him waggling his dick.
Yeah. Exactly. He don't have fucking body paint on his dick. Now, let me tell you something. I have no problem with gay people whatsoever. What I get offended by is seeing, like gay guys making out in public. But check it out. I don't like seeing heterosexual motherfuckers make out in public.
Exactly.
With my kids, you know what I'm saying? Seeing two beards rubbing, it makes me want to fucking puke. You know what I'm saying? Sorry.
Well,
I got lots of friends that are gay, but they don't try fucking me.
Got violent with the Sal and Richard being naked. You really had a violent reaction to them.
Shaggy's
making
up.
A good point. I would rather sit next to George all day than a straight guy with his cock out. I mean, that's not got nothing to do with being gay.
Yeah,
right. Their dicks are out.
Let's not forget the fucking paint on the dicks.
Yeah.
That was
the thing that took it over the top for
what,
you.
What, the insane...
Looking at your own face on somebody.
It was your face with a penis.
I was calling me out.
I was in there. I was chilling, so I looked over towards Hardy.
You feel that it was a direct challenge to you guys when they painted the Insane Clown Posse makeup on their penis.
Well, my final analysis, that their whole program was punk, otherwise they come back in and feel fist upside their fucking bitch-ass chin.
I don't think they were looking for drama. I think they were looking for something else.
Well, I'll tell you what. You guys really chased them out of the room.
Yeah.
I mean, when Shaggy 2 Dope got up and threatened to punch them, they left.
They did run like a couple of fruits.
Let me tell you something. There was no threat behind that. If they wouldn't have left, it would have went down.
They are on camera. They're out there in the hall right now.
Oh, there they are. They're brave. Brave once again.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Don't let them boys be in the hallway and not go out there neither.
No, guys, can you put away that shit and let's...
Yeah, put away your cocks.
All right. Well, you know what? That's too much for anyone to bear, isn't it?
I mean, certain things just can't be tolerated.
So, boys, you're going out on tour.
Now, what about the Juggalos? I heard that... didn't there something go down in Detroit where they were accusing fans of the Insane Clown Posse of being involved?
I heard something about, like, in Washington or some kids were dressing up as Juggalos and mugging people in parks with machetes or something.
Right.
Who said it the best? Chris Rock. What happened to just being there's some crazy motherfuckers out there?
Right.
What do you want? You know, some shit back in the day, some dude, like, listened to Mozart and started stabbing. Jack the Ripper was probably a Mozart fan. You know what I'm saying?
And there's a new album right, guys?
We have a re-release coming out of The Wraith.
A double album,
The Wraith and Hell's Pit, re-release.
And there's a 3D mini-movie attached with a violent decapitation, isn't that true? Where you remove someone's head in 3D?
That's on the Hell's Pit
album.
Yeah,
we hack and slash lots of people on that.
Oh, I want to plug our fresh news show.
Yes, I heard about this.
On the internet. It's at insaneclownposse.com.
Yes.
And the show is called The Weekly Freakly Weekly. And if you would ever like to peep, not just hear, but see all the latest and the current happenings of Shaggy 2 Dope and myself, you can check out The Weekly Freakly Weekly.
Well, you know, we have a Howard 100 News department
This is
an Insane Clown Posse news department.
Oh, and we have more informativeness, too. We also got our own internet radio station now, WFuckOff.
It's WFuckOff, yes.
Wow, good for you.
www.wfuckoffradio.com.
And when can you hear that?
Wednesday nights.
Right.
And from 9 to 1.
And what kind of show is it? Do you play music on there or you just talk?
Well, we play music and we talk.
You do it all. We cover everything. right there.
You cover it all. And do you ever bring women on there and have sex with them actually on the radio?
No, that's the, no.
No. No, but, no naked dudes are allowed in our studio.
No. What about naked women? Naked women are all right.
Naked women are allowed in the studio at all times. It right. doesn't have to be on the air.
Yeah, and you say you're getting a lot of women on the tour. You're. What, do they come on the bus still and have oral sex with you?
We keep ourselves busy like rock right. stars, you know right. what I'm saying?
Right. Right. All right. Well, listen, this sounds good. I always love getting an update from you guys.
I can't stop seeing the naked fucking penis every time I close my eyes.
I know. Well, you're going to have to go meet a woman and get
and
that
get
out
that
of
that
here.
Get that washed right out of my head.
Hey, you got to do me a favor, though, man. You can't have them boys in the hallway because I know security is about to kick my ass out. If I see them boys, I'm chinning them, man.
You are. You get into more fights. I mean, seriously. Okay.
You
so
just
let's
fight over anything.
Anything.
What are you
anything.
Talking about?
Anything.
Anything. If he would have just been mad, Nate, that'd have been cool. If he would have had some fucking underwear on, whatever, you know?
Right.
His fucking dick was chilling.
I know.
I'm going to be chilling.
Does that merit beating him up, though? I mean,
no.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
It does. No, not beating him up, pulverizing him.
Maybe because.
Because once he would have hit the floor, I'd have started stomping his fucking head like a pumpkin.
Wow.
And then next time he would have thought about doing some stupid shit like that.
Oh, you're going to. Straighten them out? Oh, forget about it.
God, I wish I totally disagreed with Shaggy.
Yeah, Artie gets very violent.
Yeah, Artie's
too.
Living this every day.
We're good.
Day.
You can come out there with me. I'll hold him. You can get a couple licks. Then we'll go to the bar and get fucked up.
You guys are tough guys. I got to say, you will fight anyone over anything. I mean, how many fights have you been in? I'm talking about man-to-man fist fights in bars.
Who knows?
No, who knows?
Yeah, man.
And you know what sucks, though? That like I'm the only one that always goes to jail.
Right. Yeah, but fighting is a different
because
story.
Because you get
into
a big ass bar brawl,
right.
But because you're like whatever famous or whatever, the police will take you to jail. And the worst part is you're in the back of the cop car and everybody out front at the bar's laughing. Ah,
do you enjoy
who's going chicken hunting now, motherfucker?
Do you like going to bars and getting into fights? Seriously,
I don't go to bars no more. No, I don't go
well,
out,
you don't
man.
Drink anymore. But I'm saying in the old days, was it something really that drew you in? You wanted to get loaded and then have a fight with someone?
No, dude, you should pop off just from. Stupid shit.
Somebody
like want
to test you. You know what I mean?
Somebody's always got something to say. You know what
look,
I'm saying?
You don't even have to be a rowdy type of person. You could be like a new, a popular fucking Martha Stewart probably
you're right.
has security
right.
with her.
You're right. There's always
because
somebody.
There's always somebody that's got to be like, oh, you mean shit. You know what I mean? Right. Just want to.
People always got to open their mouths.
Yeah, they're stunned by your presence.
Right.
Well, you know what I mean?
You guys make a lot of sense. You really do.
And with that makeup on, it's not easy to do.
Right. A couple of quick phone calls for the great insane clown posse. Always look forward to seeing the boys. Adam, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard, what's up?
Hey.
Got a couple of questions for the ICP.
Sure.
First question, do you guys, what's the word I'm looking for? Do you approve of the Juggalos, like, mugging people, killing people, whatnot?
Absolutely.
Not only that, but we endorse it.
That's right.
Who doesn't love a good mugging?
And you talk about how you're badass, you like to fight and all. Do you guys remember getting your ass kicked in Houston?
Fuck off.
45 because y'all wouldn't pay him?
What?
What? The boys got their ass kicked in Houston. Why?
By who?
I've had my ass kicked so many times. Who knows? I've been in so many fights.
Why did they get their ass kicked in Houston, according to you?
They hired a band, I-45, to open them, and they refused to pay them.
Oh, I-45. That's right.
You wouldn't pay them?
Did they kick your asses?
I don't know what the fuck it is.
Fuck.
I know it's I-75 going through Detroit.
Did you guys hire a band called I-45 and
who
forget to...
Who knows?
If there was ever a band called I-45, we didn't know about it. You know what I'm saying?
And besides, we don't pay the motherfuckers. That's the
our opening acts pay us.
We should have kicked their ass for not paying us. They probably snuck in the back into the little acoustic set or something.
Adam, the boys say they don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, well, I'm sure they forgot because they got their asses kicked nice and good.
Oh, yeah, we sure did.
Yeah.
Adam.
That's why I still got this limp.
Right. And what's the worst beating you boys ever took?
I got my ass whipped so bad I shit my pants before.
Really?
Yes. Me too.
I ain't talking wet fart. I'm talking log.
How did it happen? In other words, where were you and how did you end up shitting your pants?
Well, actually, I have on two occasions I've shit my pants. One wet, one dry.
What happened?
The dry incident, I broke into a Coney Island restaurant.
Yes.
I don't know why. I heard there was a cash boxes back in the day when I used to be a career criminal.
before
it was strictly for frozen.
Whatever. I was hungry. I wanted some
before
hot dogs.
You were famous.
Before yeah, you went into music.
I was probably like 17, 18.
17,
like that.
You broke into a restaurant.
Right. Shimmy through the drive-thru window. And right. I didn't know. It was like an independently owned restaurant. And I had no clue that the dude was in there banging his bitch in the back room.
Right.
It was all so right.
I'm like, you know, those store doors are the locks. You got to twist them a million times to open them, you know? So I'm trying to let my homie in. And I just hear, and I look, and I swear to God, this dude was a fucking giant.
Right.
And he choked me. And he choked me so hard, I took a shit. Yeah, he choked the shit out of me.
Was that the dry shit?
Yeah, that was the log. But oh, no, he goes to Catholic.
Were you very aware that you were shitting your pants, or because he was choking?
No, I was unconscious. He choked me until I was knocked out, and I woke up, and all the police were there. But here was the worst part.
He didn't kill you, obviously.
I was in jail for a day and a half with a log of shit in my ass.
You know what's funny is he told me how ruthless this guy was.
He didn't believe me.
I didn't believe him until we went to court, and I seen him in the bathroom. He looked like the Undertaker. He's fucking huge as hell. He's like,
did the judge take pity on you because you shit your pants?
Hey, that's the first time I've ever mentioned
did
it.
You do jail time?
Just like overnight. I was like 17, so I got off, you know what I'm saying?
I see. And the guy was mad at you, and he said he was going to come after
I'm just happy he didn't kill me.
Yeah,
I broke into his fucking place.
Right,
you know?
He could have killed
and
you.
He was banging his broad in the back, wow, too. I'd have killed me.
Now, how did you wet shit your pants?
I was probably like, still a young lad, maybe like 16 or so, and we beat up some girls.
Oh, my goodness. You beat up girls?
Come on, I was 16. Oh. What are you going
to
do?
All right, it happens. Yes. I mean, it doesn't happen to me. But
that's your excuse. You were 16. Right. Okay.
So whatever. We beat up a couple girls.
Why did you beat up the girls? Do you remember?
We used to jump out of the car. It was a phase. I'll tell you something.
Angry.
When you're a teenager, when you punch a girl in the face, you'll never hear a scream like it. I'm telling you.
But, I mean, isn't that a terrible thing to do? I mean, you guys have kids.
Hey, I look at it this way.
Yeah.
If a bitch thinks she's bad enough to whip a man, I'm not going to fuck out like that.
Oh, you're saying they started a fight with you?
Of course, yeah.
Oh,
I didn't just walk up and sock a hoe.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That was my
She was
there.
Hitting you and you defended yourself.
I swear on my kids, this is what happened.
They almost beat up two girls here.
Yeah, thank you. Actually, I think they're actually hermaphrodites. Because I did see a net and under the balls. But,
go ahead.
Like some bitches were on the payphone, and like we were just walking to the store, 24, like 7-Eleven type joint.
Right.
And the bitch grabbed my balls, like not ginger style, you know what I'm saying, squeezed
right,
them.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying, down on the floor.
You didn't tell me they attacked you.
You put her down.
Yeah.
But wasn't that nice? I mean, she squeezed your balls like she wanted you.
No, there was nothing nice about
it. No, she was hurting you. Why do you attract that kind of attention? Seriously.
Who knows? People
want to fight you.
I don't even remember. I probably talk shit. Who knows? But long story short, the remaining couple girls run down the street and get like they're having a party at their house. And like, so like 5 45-year-old men come out, you know. Against 2 16-year-olds, you know, one of the dudes just cracked my boy in the face, cracked his whole skull open. He was out. And I just closed my eyes and just started swinging. Next thing I know, I'm laying in the middle of the fucking street, blood everywhere, and shit in my pants.
Wet shit.
I thought my ass was bleeding. I was happy to know it was shit.
Right.
But I'll say that's the two worstest time I got my ass
kicked. Don't you guys think the violence... I don't know in the case of Shaggy, but in Violent J's life, when your mother brings in all these different men to marry, I think you become angry with women and angry at the world. Maybe that had something to do psychologically with all this anger.
Well, we don't know.
You know?
Shaggy's story. What's your family background?
Awesome.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Same shit.
Don't you think psychologically, though, Violent J?
Three kids raised by a single mom? What are you going to do?
I think my childhood was a shit, man.
I had a great childhood.
Yeah, I don't remember ever.
You know?
I mean, we were crazy.
Seems like you guys are really angry.
I was a certified ninja. I'll tell you probably what happened
was... What do you mean a certified ninja? What does that mean?
That means I actually went to Japan and am a certified ninja.
You're a ninja. You're saying you studied with ninjas and became a ninja black belt karate...
Well, we don't call it a black belt ninjutsu. Right. We call it a harakoto.
How long did you study ninjutsu?
I'm going to say probably like good 34 years.
34 years?
He started studying right after he shit his pants.
Can you turn invisible?
Huh?
Can you turn invisible?
I mean, if I had my smoke bombs with me. But,
really?
Yeah. But I don't.
Can you
I
throw
don't.
Those little stars?
No, Keltrops.
Yeah, can you throw those? Do you know how to do it? They go...
Through a mirror, backwards only. I don't do it forward.
Right. Oh, really?
Yeah. Can you kill a man with your hands?
yeah, you almost seen it.
Right.
Bring one of those motherfuckers in here. I'll show you. I'm choking life out of his face.
Wow, a ninjutsu. I'm impressed.
I know, but I'm lying. That's the problem.
Oh, okay. So you're not a ninjutsu.
But I'm nice with these.
All right. Well, listen, boys.
But he was raised by a single mom, too. How many dads did you have?
Just one.
He abandoned.
Yeah, but my stepdad pretty much raised me. So my stepdad is like my dad.
Right.
My real dad, who knows?
Who knows? Right. When your dad leaves you, though, maybe makes you angry or something. I read that in a psychology book. This guy Freud.
Crazy drunk, who knows?
Let's go to Matt. Matt, what are you doing and what are you thinking?
I really like the Insane Clown Posse.
Of course, everyone does.
Freud, who doesn't?
One of my favorite songs is Bitches, and they work with ODB, and I was just wondering if he was real interested to work with, if you guys partied with him or anything like that.
Dirty Bastard was one of my favorites.
Old Dirty Bastard is still one of my favorites, all-time favorite. How much fresher can you get?
Old Dirty Bastard, just a couple months before he passed away, he came and performed at the Gathering of the Juggalos, which is our yearly convention. And that was a real fucking honor, man.
Were you at the funeral? No, you were not.
No.
But you were close with him. You knew him. And
we knew him. He performed on a song with us, and we performed on a song on his album.
When you heard that he had died, was it hard for you? Very tough.
Yeah,
very tough. All right.
Very comparable to how it felt when Eazy-E died.
Exactly.
Right. All right. There you are. Let's go to Lewis. Lewis, go ahead. You're on with Insane Clown Posse.
A little while ago, Robin said you guys were musicians. Are you fucking kidding me?
I never said I'm a musician. I don't play the fucking
guitar. Robin said you were a musician. You guys travel with a band?
These guys are musicians. They put out records and make money out of it.
Musicians. What do they play?
Fucking, we have a fucking orchestra in the studio.
They have voices.
Hold on, let me ask you a question. What do you play, the mop?
What do you play, the deep fryer, motherfucker? What do you play?
You play the drive-through window? Fuck off.
No, I play every instrument there is, brother.
Yeah, including the skin flute, I've heard.
Well, listen.
The meat whistle, you're very proficient at.
You can't argue that ICP has sold millions of albums.
Come on, guy, we make money.
I understand that, but I mean, when they're traveling, they're talking about, our band, blah, blah, blah. You got no band, you got some fag DJ playing recorded fucking machine shit.
Okay, so just go ahead and diss all of hip-hop and rap,
right?
And all rap artists, period. They all suck. Everybody in rap, Jay-Z, Kanye West,
Let's go to Riley.
They all suck.
Riley, you're on the air.
Hey, now. Hey, Howard, Sirius is the best place for you, brother. You can't get no better than that.
We love it, and we are never going back to regular radio. We wouldn't even think of it.
Word.
It's bullshit.
Hey, look, you heard him say shit.
You're damn right you did. And I'll say it again.
Yeah, my friend.
That's right.
Artie, Robin, love you guys. ICP.
Here comes the hate. I love you, I love you, I love you. Fuck you guys.
I don't think he hates you. I think he likes you.
I can't wait to fucking see Hollow Wicked, man.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. You guys
coming here this next month, man. I'm already got.
And hey, check it out. This is the first time that we're ever taking our Hollow Wicked show on tour, full blown American tour.
It's usually a big deal in Detroit.
And if you need any information on the tour, InsaneClownPosse.com will give you everything you need to know. That's how you'll get all your information through InsaneClownPosse.com. Let's go to Angry Black. You're on the air.
Hey now. I didn't know the circus was in town, Howard.
Listen, the boys are known for their makeup. It is part of their act. It is their identity.
Yeah, they were saying that something was going to go down with Sal and Richard. The only thing that was going to go down with both of them, because they're still corny. I mean, it's wigger time.
This is the guy we got to do it with a long time ago,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
It ain't too long ago, my friend.
Yeah.
Right. Well, okay, Angry Black.
You was the guy that was nowhere to be found when we came out of the studio years ago.
If I recall correctly,
you were missing.
That's the joint that counted best.
And if I recall correctly, somehow he's on the phone.
Joel, you're on the air. We're time for only one more phone call, because ICP has to leave to catch a plane. These boys are so busy, they actually have reservations. Go ahead. Yes, Joel.
Joel, I'm a girl.
All right, Joel.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Joe Bruce. Whoa.
I just want to say, fuck the Insane Clown Posse. You guys are a couple of punks. You guys started off sounding like kind of hot.
Whoa. Do you suck your dad's cock with that mouth?
You're punching girls? Like, what? Why? That's not very manly.
See, you're the type of bitch that needs to get punched, because you talk shit like a dude.
I don't think so, buddy.
Well, it's been an exciting appearance. With insane
see,
clown
see, there's nothing worse than a bitch with a mouth like that.
Right. Imagine being that.
Well, she took offense, but you did describe that you were attacked first.
Exactly. And we were youths.
That's right.
Youths. They were youths, Robin.
That's right.
They were young and
violent.
You better That's tell right. the youth.
Violent.
I say,
well,
hey,
don't
youths,
mess with these guys.
Bulletproof.
Insane Clown Posse's Hollow Wicked Clown Tour kicks off this Friday in Grand Rapids, Michigan. If you're a fan, you're not going to want to miss it. You want to go to InsaneClownPosse.com. The boys are very important in show business. You know that because they can't even stay here any longer. I've been handed a note that says the boys need to catch
they
a plane.
They have to go.
So this is very exciting that you guys have somewhere to be.
Yeah.
Congratulations on
Just
that.
Just for today.
Now, if I see you walking down the street later.
When will I see you boys again? The visits are too frequent. I mean,
too infrequent.
Well, we have a new album coming out in February, and we if time permits. We would love to come by and say hi to you guys again. We'll even bring some donuts.
Beautiful. We love that. Artie, these guys are right in league with you.
Maybe next time some naked chicks instead of...
Yeah, how about having some chicks paint well, fucking their titties up like our faces?
I will try to get that going. I'll try to erase what happened in here and
please,
the image of that.
That shit scarred me, man.
Yeah, I know. All right, take it easy. Everyone calm down.
More than four fathers. Yeah. That shit.
Were you fans of the Munsters? You didn't watch it?
I mean, watched some Munsters.
I love that show.
When
That's
I see a big gumpy guy, I always call him Herman Munster.
Eddie Munster was coming in to play Anal Ring Toss, and the Anal Ring Toss guy didn't show up.
Oh.
We get these chicks in here, they put a stick in their ass, and you, you play Ring Toss. It's fabulous.
Where are we at for something like that?
The guy didn't show up, but Eddie Munster showed up. Butch Patrick.
Well, Mark, did he drive the Munster Mobile here?
Oh, I love that Munster Mobile, and I love the Munsters, man. It was my favorite
fucking
show.
Fucking Anal Ring Toss, all kind of fresh shit like that. Yeah. We come in there, and we got two fucking penises painted up.
I try to get something good going for you. What can I tell
you? Just think of us. Think of these painted. Think of this grease paint next time you're tossing anal rings.
Well, it was supposed to be here for you. Artie's the lord of the anal rings. That's He's the champion. Three-time champion.
Well, you telling me I can't defend my title?
So not saying, today you won't.
I'm trying to climb the ranks and issue a challenge.
We just got word that the guy was bringing in the hottest chick you ever saw. She was going to put a stick in her ass, and we were going to play anal ring toss. We haven't played since the old days on terrestrial radio.
Yeah.
And our special guest was going to be Butch Patrick to play against Artie in anal ring toss, but Butch is here. I'll bring him in just to reminisce about the Munsters and all of that. Maybe Penny Crone will do it. I don't know. I doubt it. Boys, I wish you a lot of success. I know this is a grueling time for you. A big tour coming up. You're going to be wrestling. Things have never looked better for Insane Clown Posse, and I know all your fans are excited about all of this. We will take a break, and then we'll come back, and I know you got to catch a plane, so I got to stop the fun.
Well, before you leave, Insane Clowns, what did you think of the Broadway show Lieutenants of Inishmore?
That was your question, George.
I don't think I want to
What'd
see
you think
it anymore.
Of it? All right, we'll take a break.
It was awesome. Four stars.
All right.
Thanks, everybody.
Did you guys see Jackass 2? Do you like that stuff?
I just seen it on Friday.
What'd you think? I loved it.
Funny shit.
Right? Good.
If you're into that type of... Them motherfuckers are going to kill each other, man.
That one will be dead soon, I predict. Yeah.
You see that midget? He's got, like, fuck his body. He's just one big bruise.
We
right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
It's too much. George, did you go see that movie, Jackass 2?
Number one movie this weekend,
Number one.
George.
Well, now with all this discussion, I will have to catch up on it.
Yeah, I think
you might like it because there's lots of penises in it.
George was seeing another film called Blackass.
All right. We'll be back right after these words. Insane Clown Posse. Is here. They are successes. They've just put out another album. It took them 8 grueling months in the studio, and they're here to promote. This might be their greatest record yet. I understand. Oh, there's the boys in full makeup. Hey now. Haven't seen the boys in a while. Violent J looks a little larger than he used to. He's gained some weight, I'll
be
honest.
I think Shaggy looks a little smaller.
Shaggy looks in shape, yeah. Shaggy 2 Dope, Violent J, welcome back to the show. As always, we are honored to have you here. I know you guys have been locked in the studio for 8 months on this new album. You're taking this one very seriously.
Yes, sir.
Give it everything we got in the world.
Yeah.
What do you do in the studio?
Work hard, concentrate, brainstorm, you know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, truly, we gave it every... This is the absolute best we can possibly sound today.
Someone told me your song, The Bone, might be the greatest Insane Clown Posse song yet. Is this true, in your opinion? Are they right?
I believe every Insane Clown Posse song is the greatest Insane Clown Posse song.
I don't like the way your mic sounds. I don't, Shaggy, I don't like the way the microphone sounds.
We can hardly hear you.
I didn't know I had a mic.
Yeah, you got a mic on those headphones, but...
oh, shit.
Anybody else think it sounds okay?
It doesn't.
No, I know what to do.
What's
perhaps
wrong?
Perhaps any different headphones.
I don't want to miss a word of the boys. I mean, I waited a long time to see them.
Check.
Testing, 1, 2.
1, 2. 1, 2. Check. Woo!
I like it better.
Yeah?
Sounds good now. Now
that's
it's
better.
Good.
That's better.
Boys, when you put the makeup on this morning, how long does it take you? You were in full clown makeup. I appreciate. You don't come in here and, you know, you could easily...
Pretending you're in clown makeup.
Yeah, you could say, let's pretend we're in clown makeup.
Well, actually, it's tattooed on.
Now, come on. Mm-hmm. Seriously, how long does it take you to get the makeup on?
It takes me about 15 minutes.
Is that true?
Yeah.
It takes me about
a half hour.
It's got to be more than 15 minutes. That is way involved, what you got there.
I've been doing this 17 years. It's pretty easy. I can do it in the dark. I can do it in a moving car.
Really?
Yeah.
Even around the mouth, though, it's very involved. It's not like it's very specific lines. It's even.
It's funny because for the first 5 years of our career, Shaggy always did both our makeup.
Really?
Yeah, and then I got sick of it. I was like, man, you got to do your own shit.
Right.
Learn your shit, man.
Right.
It was pretty easy.
Yeah, what are you, the makeup artist? I mean, what are you supposed to do?
Right, exactly. I don't swing that way.
Now, is it true that the Juggalos, which is the name for your followers, everyone knows the Insane Clown Posse followers are Juggalos. Is it true recently, and you do this every year, you have like a Woodstock for all Juggalos. In other words, you say to all your fans, come to this one place, we'll have an outdoor festival, and everyone can congregate. Is that true?
Yeah.
But it's controversial, isn't it? Because now in some states, Insane Clown Posse fans, Juggalos, are considered gang members. Isn't that true?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why is that, though?
Because it's misunderstood.
It is.
You know, the gathering of the Juggalos is, you know, there's no words in the English language, the tongue cannot possibly translate how magically fresh the gathering of the Juggalos is, you know?
How many people show up for your version of Woodstock?
This year?
Yeah.
This year we had about 20,000 people.
20,000 people. And this goes mostly unnoticed by the media.
But this year was also the 10th annual.
And when you guys go there, when you finally hit the stage, it's like God walks on the stage, right? People don't realize this.
Well, you know, we're everywhere throughout the whole weekend, you know what I mean?
You hang out with your fans?
Oh, yeah, we're on golf carts riding through the woods.
You guys don't consider yourselves better than your fans? You don't, you're not hidden backstage? In other words, you can't talk to the fans?
There's nothing Hollywood about us.
Exactly. You got to be a part of that party, you know what I'm saying? If you're put on a party like that, you want to be a part of it.
You want to be a part of it.
But, you know, a lot of rock stars, like the Stones, they don't hang out with their fans in the crowd before the show. They keep this mystery about themselves.
Oh, we don't do that either. We don't hang out in the crowd before the show. We feel like you got to save that for when you pop out on the stage. You know, shows are different. But the gathering of the Juggalos, 4 days and four nights in the middle of nowhere,
right?
You know, that's a party.
Show up because you are Insane Clown Posse, there are a lot of women there too, right? It's not just all guys.
Yeah.
And they want to blow you and do all kinds of sexual acts with you, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, it's got to be wild for you guys. Two guys who grew up the hard way. I mean, it wasn't like you were handed anything. I mean, do you take advantage? I know. Now, Shaggy, you've got three kids.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't get blowjobs from...
Two are teenagers, too.
Yeah, you can't get blowjobs from Juggalos, can you?
I mean...
Juggalettes.
Juggalettes. Don't get that mistruled, please.
You understand what I'm saying. I mean, if a Juggalo wanted to blow, you wouldn't let him.
Don't put me in that boat.
Yeah, right.
My swing don't swing that way.
I know. You guys are very uptight about homosexuality, aren't you? You guys never try it. You never tried.
No, I never fucking dabbled, no.
No, but the fact is, when you were a boy growing up, your father left you. Am I correct?
Yep.
That's right. Violent J. A lot of people don't know this about him. Very painful past. His father left him. Your stepfather, you claim, tried to have sex with you. Is that true?
Well, all the information.
Isn't that true?
Yeah, that's true.
And what kind of sex was he looking at? How old were you?
What was that like? Yeah. How did he approach?
Yeah. He was a fucking pedophile.
He was, right?
Yeah.
How old were you at this point?
I was probably 5 or 6 or 7.
Yeah.
No, kidding.
He was with us in our family for like maybe 4 years.
So what did he try to do to you? Did he try to touch your penis?
Well, you know, he tried to juggle my balls. You know what I'm saying?
Perhaps a finger in the anus.
What do you want to put his finger in your asshole?
No.
Perhaps tried to.
That's speculation on his part.
Shaggy thinks maybe there was a finger in your ass.
Not that finger in my ass is any better than juggling my balls.
Did he kiss you?
No.
What? You never made out with your stepfather?
Was it that sitting on the lap thing? And
no, he would walk around in a robe with his dick hanging out.
Oh.
You know, and you know, it was just, it was a nightmare, you know, but I was the youngest of three kids, you know.
So he probably tried to pick on you the most because he figured you're an easy victim.
Or maybe the least, I don't know.
I don't know, man. You know, what happened with your other siblings? Did he get into their pants or not?
That's a fucked up way of putting it.
But did he? I mean, was he successful? I mean, first of all, how did you avoid, like, touching him or sucking him off or something like that? Because you were so young, you could have been abused or beaten into it.
God. Yeah. There was no sucking him off going on.
I understood, but
and
I'm saying.
And he didn't try to do anything to you?
Little kids sometimes can't fight.
He juggled my balls.
He juggled your balls?
Like, do you know what these are? You know?
Yeah, I know what they are.
You know what I'm saying?
What did you say?
Offered a bag of hot fries and it was
and then he'd have like fucking porno magazines sitting out. He was just a creepy old pedophile.
He had all the tricks. He had the magazines, the whole thing. And then he's asking you, do you know what these are? And did you know what they were?
No, not really.
Not at 5.
I thought they were magic books.
No, I mean, did you know what balls were? No.
Oh, not really.
No, man, this is painful shit. I'm not trying to, you know.
Right. Rigging anything up.
That's right. Control. Where is he now?
I'm fucking probably dead.
You think? You don't even look for him?
I mean, we used to want to kill him. Me and my brother used to want to track him down and kill him.
Do you think that's why you became violent, Jay?
Could be.
Yeah, right? You got to be angry over that. Where was your mom during all this?
Work.
Exactly.
So he wasn't like this when she was around?
No, hell no.
Did he hide the magazines and everything? Just pull them out when she was gone?
When my mom, I remember the day my mom found out.
How did she find out?
Everybody got a secret porno spot in the house.
Yeah, right. but his stepdad was sharing it with the kids.
Right.
You know.
Because my sister, that's not right. My sister had ran away and left a detailed note. So, you know, and he didn't know. He came home from work like everything was gravy, you know. And my mom started throwing dishes and, you know, it was.
She kicked him out.
It was mass pandemonium in the house.
Hey, at least your mom kicked him out. There's some moms they don't believe the kid.
And he tried to send money at Christmas, and she sent it back. You know, that's what I remember.
Right, because she didn't want his dirty money.
Right, I wanted that money.
It was probably mad dirty. Yeah. Going through his hands was all over some kid's ass.
Right.
But there was many, just so I can say, there was many thoughts of going back and killing him. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
There was plenty of thoughts of that.
If I brought him in here, I'm going to bring him in a few minutes. So I might as well tell you. Yeah, your stepdad. We tracked him down. What would you do to him if I brought him in?
Kill him right here.
You would kill him in the studio.
Come on. It would be mass murder going on in here.
That would be really good radio.
Unfortunately, we didn't find him.
Yeah, I'm going to look for him.
Had we known.
And let's have a reunion right now.
Should we ask him to leave? He's sitting over here.
I mean, it's unbelievable. Yeah, it's Benji. So it's
I know if we couldn't find him, you guys can't find him.
Do you love, you must love your mother for that, because when she found out, she stuck up for you kids, right?
I don't just have a mom, I have like a super mom.
No kidding.
Yeah, my mom's.
Did you set her up with, when you guys became rich and famous and you became, you know, the Great Insane Clown Posse, did you set up your mom with a nice house, some sort of...
I continue to take care of my mom as best I can.
Really?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
That means, you know, whenever she needs anything, I try to be there for her, you know?
So she is your burden.
My burden?
Yes. You have to take care of your mom. You feel this
feels good. It
you
feels
like
great, yeah, helping my mom, you know?
Does your mom ever attend any of your concerts when the Juggalos all get together?
She sure does, you
she
know?
She does, so she's supportive.
My mom doesn't get around as much as she used to, you know? She's getting older. She's heavy, you know? She doesn't get around that much, you know, like that.
Why
all the shows and shit?
Why are you eating so much? Shaggy is in top shape. I see.
I ain't in top shape.
Sure, you are. Come on, look at you. You're thin. You're lean. You probably got a six pack. What is going on with Violent J? I'm worried about
your health. No, I'm drinking six packs.
Filet mignons every night, man.
Are you guys a victim of your own success? Are you eating too many good foods? Are you going to too many fancy restaurants?
It's just the shirt I'm wearing makes me look fat. I'm actually thin like Shaggy.
Are you concerned about your health, about the diabetes or anything like that?
I love myself. I love who I am. Let me tell you something. For me to be skinny is unnormal for me. That's not who I am.
Right.
I got to work around the clock. Just to maintain be skinny. To maintain skinniness. You know what I'm saying? And I was on a health kick a few years ago, running every night, you know.
It was killing you.
Tough work, you know. Then I had kids.
Right.
And my priorities kind of changed.
Are you married now?
No. Not married, but I have a girl, you know, been together for a while.
And you have kids with her, and you're faithful to her?
Yeah.
So when you guys have a concert, no one's getting any sex?
Not anymore, man.
Really?
We had enough sex to last us for our life.
Man,
Shaggy, what about you?
Nah, I'm still married.
What? The hell's going on?
I mean, I've been separated off and on.
You know
what I'm saying? But, you know, I don't. If I'm with my wife, I don't be fucking around.
Man, I can't believe what I'm hearing. You guys aren't that...
They're not that insane.
Are you not that insane? Are blowjobs okay when the girl comes backstage and wants to do that? I mean, is that all right? Is that cheating?
You tell me.
Yeah, I mean, what do you think?
You know, you got to understand, though, before that,
we
had enough and did enough the last three or four lifetives.
Oh, come on.
They're saying clown posse.
You're saying clown posse.
The same clown posse.
You guys are talking way sane. Don't you think you're
talking like everybody else?
You guys are not so insane clown posse.
But you know, that's the funny thing. You're a reasonable clown posse now.
we're actually the rational clown posse.
Yeah. I remember when you guys were nuts. All right, some of the things that go on at your version of Woodstock, I want to point out here, because a fan wrote me and said, you had to be there. It was wild.
Now, how many people are we talking about?
20,000.
If you've never been there and you've never experienced it, there's really no way to describe it. You know what I'm saying?
At the gathering, this guy described it. People take showers in trailers. Girls also participate in an obstacle-type thing event and oil wrestling, both in bra and panties. So the girls strip down in bra and panties.
And that's all naked.
And naked and oil.
Well, there's lots of naked chicks walking around.
Really?
They're just walking around.
Just walking
there's
around.
There's no
asshole
police
naked.
On the entire
asshole
grounds.
Naked, just
wow.
Walking around.
It's absolute insanity.
Fans also do crazy wrestling matches on their own, making each other bleed with barbed wire, bashing each other over the head with chairs and signs and whatnot.
Really?
Sure.
Uh-huh. No kidding. Is that fun? Do you guys get into any of the fights? Do you fight anyone?
No, there's no fighting. You know,
that's all I love. That's like just kids wrestling, like backyard wrestling. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but Violent J was sued recently because he sprayed some kid with a soda bottle and he claimed something happened with his eye or something like that. What was that?
So many lawsuits, brother.
Still?
So many lawsuits.
How many are against you right now?
I'd say there's probably four.
Four lawsuits.
Yeah.
One of them was, I guess you guys like to spray soda on your fans while you're performing, right? That's one part of
your
act.
See, we should get called Get Sued Clown Posse.
I know. It's unbelievable. And it costs you a lot of money, I'm sure, and lawyers and all this kind of stuff.
But we don't just throw soda. We throw, you know, about 400 2-liters a night off the stage.
Right.
Kicking them, launching them. We can do things with a 2-liter of Faygo you didn't know were possible.
A Faygo's a soda, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you take the Faygo and you kick it. Off the stage.
Kick it, squirt it, pelt it.
And what is this guy claiming? That he was injured by the Faygo bottle and he wants $50,000?
Probably. Crybabies every now and then.
Yeah, crybaby bitches.
Big time. Come on, man. I've been had my ass whipped so many fucking times. You know what I'm saying?
That's true. You guys have been in real fights.
Everybody knows you come to an ICP show, get hit in the head with a Faygo and sue. You're nothing but a
quit being
bitch
a fucking
ass
sissy
bitch.
Why Faygo? Is Faygo your sponsor? Do they embrace you at all?
No, nothing like that. It's the poor man's pop. You know what I mean?
You
it's 99 cents for a 2-liter.
And you love Faygo.
Yeah.
And so the fans stand there and they love when you kick the Faygo into their face. Right?
Yeah.
It sounds crazy,
we also get it back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right.
I get poked in the head every night.
Yeah, we get hit the shit all night.
Did you say to the guy afterwards, wait, well, why are you suing me, man? It's no big deal.
Fuck that guy. I don't even know who they are.
Right. So you just let your lawyer handle it and that's the end of it.
I just know he's a cocksucker. That's all.
Well, come on. I mean, be fair. Maybe the guy really was hurt. Maybe he wants just a little bit of dough or something.
I've never sued one person in my life over getting hurt. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I've broken my neck twice, fucked my back up, broken my elbows.
How did you break your neck? In a fight?
No. From one time, I actually broke it twice. I broke it once from wrestling.
Right.
And a second time from stage diving, but I climbed up like a lighting tier.
Was that at a Paul Simon concert?
Yeah. I was actually at the Gathering.
Were you?
Yeah. Well, in the middle of our set.
You guys have gotten your ass kicked so bad, and I've heard you describe this, that you've actually shit your pants, right, Violent J?
God, what the fuck is going on, man?
Is it true that you shit your pants?
I can't front, I have.
You
yeah,
have to?
I shit my pants. Yeah.
What happened? In other words, who were you fighting, and how did you shit your pants?
I literally got the shit kicked out of me.
It's true, right? Because, in other words, the guy was hitting you so hard.
Well, no, this was when I was younger, though, because I broke into a Coney Island.
Yes.
And, so you shit your pants twice getting your ass kicked, because the other time...
Right. Yeah, but, yeah, I was...
When you beat that chick up, them dudes came back and knocked the shit out of your butt then, too.
You beat up a chick?
I was younger.
You wouldn't do that now, would you?
No, I mean, unless she punched me in the face or something.
Why did you hit a woman? I mean, I can't imagine.
Because she squeezed my balls too hard.
Really?
Yeah.
During sex or was
no,
it?
No, no, it was just walking down the street. She was on a payphone and we were just going to a store. And
she was a wild, big, tough bitch.
And she squeezed your ball, like, out of nowhere.
So
you were injured.
Put her on the floor.
Right. Well, maybe I understand that. Robin, what do you think of that?
It was a reflex. He was attacked.
It was a reflex.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? A chick fucking grabs your nuts like that and squeezes them like to try to pop them. What are you going to do?
I'm not talking about a feminine little butterfly. We're talking about a big,
and we're not talking about like a little nut hoist. You know what I'm saying? We're not talking about
like she did it to hurt you.
Yeah, like she was trying to tear my fucking balls off my dick.
Oh.
Wow. Well, then you got a point.
I guess that deserves a hit.
She went and got her boys, and like by the time I got back to my house, you know what I'm saying? It was like, I was probably like, I don't know, like probably like 17 or something, and like these dudes were like 40.
How many guys?
So probably like four. They just bounced my head off the concrete, and the worst part was I was wearing white shorts.
Right. and all of a sudden you find yourself shitting.
I got back to my crib. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I just had a big fucking brown dude stain in my ass.
Wow. Why did she grab your balls in the first place? I bet she was attracted to you. You're a handsome guy.
Well, thanks.
Well, I mean, everybody knows it. You guys are probably the hottest guys in rock right now. I mean, physically, I'm talking about, right? I mean, despite their clown makeup, I mean, when you guys wash that off, I know you're a handsome guy.
I always get mistaken for Justin Timberlake.
You know? Do, right?
Yeah, a lot of times. Whenever I walk down the street, they're like, hey, JT. I'm like, no, not me.
When you're in the middle of getting beaten up, and you shit your pants, and you're wearing all white. Do the guys
give a fuck?
No, I know you don't give a fuck, but do the guys give a fuck we're beating up? Do they notice you shit your pants?
I'm not the guy... I don't know. See, when I'm beating somebody up,
right.
I don't look at their ass.
Right. You're too busy fighting.
Right, I'm too busy.
Be honest, it doesn't take a long time to beat a guy up. I mean, it's over pretty much in a punch or two, right? Don't you agree?
It's not UFC. You know what I'm saying? With those rules and shit. Rounds, you grab a brick and shit.
When I shit my ass, I was getting beat up by like three or four dudes.
Why? Why are you getting beaten up?
Well, we went to a concert, and we were coming out of the concert, and some chick was getting messed with by some drunk dude, and so the guy I was with decided to stand up for her defense, and I was with him. And so anyway, a big fight broke out, and there was like three or four dudes kicking my ass, and the shit just came out of my butt. The punches were coming so fast and ferociously, and I was so stunned.
I've never heard of this phenomenon.
I ran into a Chinese restaurant, ran into the women's bathroom. You know, running for my life, basically, you know.
Right.
And then I realized that I knew I shit my pants right when it happened. Took my drawers off, threw them in the
garbage.
Yeah, and then you know that changed everything. I wiped my butt clean,
right,
and fucking came out of there more or less still looking, you know, making sure I was safe from the yeah.
Do you guys pride yourselves on the fact that you've been in fights, that you've kicked guys' asses?
Well, let me tell you something.
And you can take a beating.
With the shit in the ass thing, right quick.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Before we're off that subject.
Right, yeah.
Anybody who's been in as many fights and like got their ass kicked and kicked as many asses before, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
If they say they have not shit their pants by getting their ass whipped at least one time, they're a fucking liar.
Yeah, I mean, I've had my ass kicked a million times.
And you never shit your pants.
I never shit my pants. But I got beat up pretty good. You know, I mean, I tried to get off a few punches. Look at me. I mean, you know what I mean?
You gotta kick some ass.
I tried.
You got the reach on
shitting your pants saying, I shit my pants coming home from Thanksgiving dinner this year.
Yeah.
Oh, man, what a story.
Now, what about you guys? You kids, your kids who are growing up now, Do they know how to fight? Do you toughen them up? Do you make
them rich do. Kids? Come
I
on.
Mean, you got rich kids.
No, kids are
you guys are multimillionaires, right?
Yeah, our but you kids are learning the streets.
What do you mean in the streets? You guys
I mean, our kids are learning coming up the way we came.
Mine
are because my kids like I got like half custody. But my kids stay with their mom. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And she don't live in a friendly neighborhood or nothing like
really?
That.
Really?
Yeah.
Don't you support them?
I take
them?
Care of them. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I mean, they come out to my house and they're cool. You know what I'm
right.
saying?
But when they're living with their mom,
but
it's
they
not
go to
so
public good. Schools around there and everything. You know what I'm saying?
And wow. they know that you're their dad.
Yeah.
Wow.
Do you guys ever put the clown makeup on in front of the kids?
I box my kids and stuff.
You do box them?
Yeah, with I teach the them how to box and stuff. Yeah,
tough
man,
them
I got the sweetest picture in my living room of Shaggy with his two kids sitting on his lap and all three, you know, the twin boys.
Yes.
And they all got clown makeup on. It's the sweetest picture.
Outfit. Great dad. I love it. Listen, you got to teach the kids how to fight. They're going to need
course.
It's a skill
absolutely.
They need. Absolutely.
Especially once they get to high school, you know what I'm saying? And everybody figures out who their dad is. They're going to want to fuck with them, you know what I'm saying?
Doesn't the mom sue you for more money? She says, a lot of these women will say, hey, my the guy I had the kids with, he's got a great lifestyle. And then my kids come home and it's a shitty neighborhood.
Of course.
So how do you get away with not giving her more money?
It's not a shitty neighborhood.
He doesn't,
guys.
First
it's
of all,
suburb,
he doesn't
you know
get away with it.
No,
he
I
gives
don't.
Her you crazy don't. Bucket loads
I get
of money.
Raped in my ass.
You do?
Yeah.
You're paying a lot of support.
Insane yes, fucking money. It's not even my business, but let me chime in.
Right.
Fucking ridiculous,
that's
stupid,
why
insane,
insane
money.
Okay.
Let me change the topic for 1 minute here. You guys had an unbelievable episode on our radio show years ago with Sharon Osbourne.
She never paid up.
No, she did not.
What was the bet?
Bet was she bet that Insane Clown Posse couldn't sell X amount of albums, and you guys did. You met.
We oversold it.
We right. sold that limit. Albums and albums. She had the same argument everybody had.
Right.
That, you know, we were just here for the fucking summer.
Right.
You know what I mean? And we've proven that wrong. We've been 10 years we've been coming on here.
Right.
Whatever happened to that bitch?
Well,
where's she at now?
I was going to say,
well,
she's
actually kind of large.
Oh, she blew up.
Kind of large.
No, she actually lost weight.
No,
she's
she
huge.
She looks like a model now.
She looks like a model, and she's making. She's a huge star on TV. She's on the number one show on NBC as a judge.
That's you know what?
How much I
she came up
TV.
In the world, which means she could really pay. And we said,
I hit it just to say I hit it.
Right, but do you think, in a way, are you upset by this success that she has?
No, man. I just
hate
think she should have paid up.
She didn't. Yeah, she never gave us a.
She was tough.
And here's the whole thing, though. The whole thing, though, we didn't even want the fucking money. We said, just let us put it into a charity in our name.
In our right. name, you right. know?
Not your name.
You can even pick the charity.
Like, she couldn't afford that. Come on.
The new album is called...
She might have changed her appearance just to avoid paying you guys.
There you go.
The new album is called Bang Pow Boom.
Yeah.
What?
Came out
Bang
today.
Pow Boom.
It came out today.
This is a big day. This is a big day. I'm
a
probably
huge day.
Filled with promotion. Are you on your own record label or are you working still with some other record
no,
label?
No, we're on our own Psychopathic
totally
Records.
Is that the way to make money now? The record business is very
difficult.
That's
the only way to make money now.
You have to be on your own label. How do you sell? How do you distribute the record?
Every rapper is trying to go independent. Even Ice Cube's independent now.
Is that
Pearl Jam's independent now.
And what does that mean to be independent? In other words, where do people get your new album? How do they get
it? They get it any store anywhere, you
right.
know, from Best Buy to anywhere they sell CDs.
Now, how do you get distribution now if you're doing your own thing?
Through Sony.
Through Sony.
Oh, through Sony.
So yeah. That's what the record companies are doing.
All right.
Right, you just get a distributor. That way you get the label money. Because, like, I've been reading, like, crazy, like, magazines, you know what I'm saying? They're saying, like, the new gold should be, like, 100,000 records.
Right.
You know
what
I'm
saying? Yeah, you can't sell records no more today.
With the internet, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
There's no way.
The money's really in touring, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And merchandise.
And you guys are out on tour all the time?
We got the massive 64-city tour launching September 16th.
When will you be in the New York area where I am?
Somewhere along those. Are you going
to
come?
Yeah, I have to go see what's doing this time. But I'm a little afraid. I mean, I don't want to get soda thrown on me.
Go to the back. Well, you're not safe.
I don't want to get that.
You wouldn't sue them if you got hit with Fago.
Absolutely, I would.
You wouldn't sue them?
Fagola, soda? I mean, what am I going
to
do with that?
I think if you came and saw the spectacle, you'd want the Fago on you. You'd want to be part of the party.
Be part of the scene, yeah. Yeah. Well, maybe so. Listen to this. This is an amazing headline in the world of Insane Clown Posse. In 2008, a high school in Oregon banned students from wearing Insane Clown Posse paraphernalia, claiming the items are gang-related. What is going on here with this gang stuff? ICP Juggalo fans are considered gang members in several states, including Utah and California. In 2008, two Utah Juggalos were arrested for trying to kidnap a 5-year-old boy. In July 2008, two Utah Juggalos attempted to kill a teenager with a knife and a 4-bladed replica of a medieval battle axe. The teenager's wounds required more than 300 stitches. What are you guys, what's going on here?
First of all, let me just say this.
Like the State of the Union.
The Juggalos aren't just ICP fans. Juggalos have manifested into something bigger.
It's become some sort of thing.
Yeah, it's
morphed.
Yeah, absolutely. It's not just, they're not fans of ICP, just that all, we might provide the soundtrack for them, but Juggalos are bigger than that,
Is it beyond your control now, your fans?
Absolutely.
It is.
There are some Juggalos that are just not right in the fucking head, just like some normal people ain't right in the fucking head.
You're telling me some Juggalos aren't right in the head?
what about all the people that commit crimes and aren't Juggalos,
Of course. If you think about it, for the amount of Juggalos out there, and there's quite a few, there's not that much crime within the Juggalo community.
You could come, 20,000 people, no police, almost everybody inebriated, right? All weekend, not one fight, man.
True. Let's take a phone call. Let's hear from Jim. Jim is excited to talk to the Insane Clown Posse. Of course, we're sitting here with two big stars, Violent J and Shaggy 2 Dope.
Yeah, Howard, how you doing?
Hey.
These guys are faggots, man. They're fucking barely one.
How'd I guess?
Yucko the Clown.
Hey, check it out. Hey. If I was a fag, you'd try hitting on me right now.
Hey, listen, I didn't suck my father's cock when I was 17 either.
Well, neither did they. Listen.
Yeah, you didn't try to. You actually did.
All right, but go ahead. Let's not get
into this. The only way you can diss us is to make shit up. That's ridiculous. How about let's talk facts, bitch.
I got a 19-year-old kid, and he's a Juggalo. And he needs a fucking job, man. Him and his friends, they walk around the town spray painting shit.
So how are you going to diss your son? You're a piece of shit.
You're telling me, wait a second, Jim. But let's understand this.
What a fuck, ass.
You say your son is a Juggalo, and he's an idiot?
Yeah, he's a fucking idiot. He doesn't have a job. He worships these fucking morons with makeup.
Who's the real fucking moron here?
I mean, are you jealous of ICP that your son is...
are you jealous of the fact we have a bigger influence on your son than you do?
Yeah, it's a bad influence, though, dude. Why don't you send a positive message out there? None of your fans have jobs, probably, man.
Well, listen, I mean...
Yeah, I went to see my kid down at... he was having a get-together with some of his friends, so I went down to see him, and his one friend's wearing his necklace with a fucking hatchet man around his neck, right? I said, what the fuck is that thing? He goes, it's hatchet man for ICP, so I took it and shoved it up his fucking ass.
See, he's calling us a fag.
Right.
Hey, man, he's calling us a fag.
He's putting stuff
up little boys' asses.
Let's go to Steve. Maybe he has a more positive message for ICP. They're here to celebrate their new album.
Shoved it up his ass.
Hey, now.
Hey, well, about that last caller, he's definitely a fucking faggot. Because I'm an ICP fan, and I own my own fucking business, so he can go fuck himself. And I got three fucking kids that adore me. So, besides that, I want to know if you guys still got beef with Eminem and D12.
Yeah, now, who are you feuding with? You used to feud with Eminem. You'd go in the studio, you would record terrible things
That's
about Eminem.
That's so old.
It's old. You're not feeling angry toward him anymore?
We're actually cool with D12 now.
Yeah. D12 and Eminem are your friends?
We never met Eminem.
Do you like him now?
We haven't had a chance to squash anything.
Right.
But,
what was the beef anyway? I don't even remember. Do you?
Yeah, I remember. It's just old, stupid shit from Detroit.
What do you mean? Oh, right. Back in the day, he used to put you guys down.
Yeah. But, there was a couple opportunities where we were in the same building, and we wanted to, just squash the beef in person.
Right.
And he wouldn't come down.
Because you're shook.
He's probably afraid of you, right?
So maybe, we squashed all the beef with D12.
Right.
In person, we had a big bowling match in Detroit.
I like that. I like that you guys have reached out, olive branch, and this and that. Did you guys get political during the last election? Did ICP urge the Juggalos to vote at all? Do you ever do any of that kind of work?
Come on, man. I got so many felonies. I can't vote anyways.
Because of all your felonies, you can't vote?
Oh, come on. You can't vote when you got like five felonies.
You have five felonies?
Something like that.
Do you know what they're all for?
Mostly.
What are they?
Well, since they're his, I would hope he knew.
If I had five felonies, I'd know. Name the five felonies.
I think one is B&E, one's home invasion, one is concealed weapon, one is weapon charges, one is, I don't know, just... All types of stupid
All type of stuff. But not anymore. I mean, when's the last time you had a felony?
Like last year.
Last year? Yeah. What was that one for?
The B&E and the home invasion. And
breaking
the
and entering?
No,
last...
this was home invasion.
Oh, home. What was home? What happened?
I stuck a kid up in his house.
Why? But you're a wealthy rock star. Why are you sticking up a kid in his house?
It's a long story, man. Everybody called it like an OJ trial. You know what I'm saying? Because, like,
the kid had something of his in his house.
Right, and that one got it.
What did he have?
My mom's house back in the day got broken into, and he had a piece of studio equipment that I bought for my little brother.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Because my little brother's a producer, you know?
Right.
And so I was at my boy's, like, mom's barbecue for her birthday or whatever, and he showed me on a computer. You know, I don't know shit about computers. I don't even know how to turn one on.
Really? I would think, like, you guys in the studio use computers a little bit, no?
I don't even know how to turn one on.
You're not interested? You don't want to learn?
Hey, I'm technologically, however you say that word, declined.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Understood. All right, so some guy hands you a computer and says, look at this, here's your equipment.
Right, and they knew because it had, like, some scratching in it and stuff, so I was like, right. I just happened to have a gun on me, and I was like, let's go.
You walk around with a gun?
I have one. Yeah, and I just pushed it in his face and went into his house.
When you say you just happen to have a gun, isn't that a technicality in the law? In other words, it wasn't premeditated. You just happen to have a gun on you. But you went and got the gun, or you just happen to have it?
I just happened to have it on me.
Really? What kind of gun?
Nine Ruger.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Look at you. So you're walking around.
Well, long story short, I'm not allowed to have guns no more.
Of course not. Well, a 9 Ruger, you can't walk around.
Well, you should. You don't know what to do with it.
Right. Well, yeah. He actually did what you are supposed to do with a gun.
No, he
the dude ran out of his house.
Call the police.
All right.
You want your shit back?
The dude's shit is
Yeah, I got it back.
Yeah, you got it back. I'm sure you did.
And you got,
I didn't give it back then.
And dude ran out of his own house. And I told my boy, I said, man, you better go get that right now. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Okay.
So, you know, I had him covered.
You know what's funny, though, if you think about it? Here you are, you're a success. You got plenty to live for. You never probably even think about that equipment. And all of a sudden, this guy riles you up.
It was my little brother's shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but you know what I mean? Like, if this guy hadn't shown you that on the computer, you never would have gotten into trouble. You know, it was almost like a mantra thing. You had to go get back your stuff.
Well, here goes the whole thing, Howard.
Right.
And I'll be honest with you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm like full-blown alcoholic. You know what I'm saying? I was a little bit tipsy that day, probably.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I thought you were in rehab recently.
Yeah.
And how'd you make out with that?
I've been in and out of rehab forever.
How many times?
Shit. I don't fucking even. I can't even count.
Over 10 times.
Yeah. Really?
I can't count.
Do you ever talk to him about his drinking?
Oh, hell yeah.
Man, that's my best friend in the world.
So what does that mean?
It means we go through it together.
Occasionally you show up here alone, or you're on the phone alone, and we don't know where Shaggy is. Is that where he is in rehab?
That's right.
I see.
Yeah.
Is it what? Just drinking, Shaggy?
Out of the bed. Yeah, just drinking. I know drugging.
Have you, What?
It ain't just drinking.
It ain't just drinking? What are you doing? Lying to us?
I'm in denial.
What does he do? Finally, Jay, what does he do?
I'm in denial.
What does he do?
He takes funky-ass pills.
Really?
Yeah.
Why do you say, if we ask you if you just drink, and then you say you...
Because I'm an alcoholic, I'm a fucking liar.
Oh, I see.
And I eat too much, you know what I'm saying?
All right, so you guys, you're human. That's
We're
what you
human,
say.
Man.
You can't be God all the time. So right. When's the last time you went to rehab? How many months ago?
Like 2 weeks ago?
So you're back. You already back to drinking again?
No.
Oh,
I can't no more. Otherwise, I'll die.
You're sober.
What's going on?
You're sober now. 2 weeks?
No, 2 days.
2 days. He's sober.
He just got through detoxing.
No, I quit drinking 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago, you quit drinking.
Yeah.
Detox.
Detox.
Yeah.
And what about the pills? Did you quit those?
Yeah.
You believe him?
I can talk to my boy right now.
He can tell when I'm fucked up or not.
This is Shaggy Tudor.
But I can honestly tell you this: I've never been to this show drunk.
No, I know that. You were always a pro when you were here.
But let me ask you something. You say now you'll die. So what's wrong with you?
Because if I keep drinking, I'll get cirrhosis of the liver.
Uh-huh.
How much do you drink?
Like up to 2 fifths a day.
Jesus Christ.
Mackerel.
What do you drink?
I mean, it depends upon whether I'm binging or not.
What do you like to drink?
Vodka, of course.
You love it, right?
Every alcoholic is either Jack Daniels or vodka.
And what do they do for you in rehab? Do they sit there and talk to you?
No, you go through detox, you know what I'm saying? And
yeah. You get the shakes and all that other stuff.
Yeah,
that's tough.
You gotta go to meetings and all that shit, you know?
And Violent J, do you get so angry with him when he's drinking because it fucks up the whole band and the whole thing?
It doesn't fuck up the band. It's more, you know, my boy.
Right.
That's my little brother.
Right. But is he annoying to deal with when he's drinking a lot?
It's crazy, crazy painful.
Yeah. So it's a pain in the ass.
I put a lot of people through a lot of shit, man.
Right. So
but at the same time, we'll always be there.
Do people know in rehab who you are, but now you're walking around without the makeup?
Usually I go to the ones that, like, you know, where they got, like, a clause where they can't talk about it and stuff like that.
Oh, I see. You know, you ever see other famous people there?
No.
Oh, you ain't going to a shitty one. You got to go to one where you can hang out with, like, cool...
I was in rehab with a famous guy.
Yeah, you want to be...
I was in rehab with a famous guy. I wish I could say who.
Yeah, right.
I can't.
Yeah, yeah, see?
You're not allowed.
What good is it? You can't talk
to... But I was in a rehab where they let you wear makeup to the meetings.
I get it.
So wait a second. So let me understand where we're at this point. The band is very much together, always will be. The band is successful. We got the new album out. I should mention the new album is called, first of all, you got to hear a little of this. This is The Bone. What is The Bone about? Is that about your bone? Like your
penis? No, it's about, you know, a guy's going on a crazy homicidal murder binge, and everybody he comes across is getting the bone, you know, which means they're getting fucked up. You know what I mean? They get the bone.
We've been saying that, like, our whole lives. Like, you know what I'm saying? If you get fucked up, you get the bone.
All right. Like, when we came on the show
last time. If something bad happens to you, you get the bone.
Remember when we came on the show last time and the guys came out with their dicks painted up like us?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We got the bone.
Right, right, right. The guys wanted to come back in naked again with you guys, but I told them not to.
That wouldn't have, yeah.
Those guys almost got the bone, though.
Right, okay,
here we go. Has the jury reached the verdict?
Yes, Your Honor. We find the defendant guilty on all counts.
The bailiff came at me with a pair of cuffs in his hand. He was taking me to jail, but that wasn't my plan. I broke the arm off my chair, stabbed him hard as I can. He got the ball.
He got the ball!
I jumped over the other...
Let me ask you something. You think the Juggalos now are all going to be saying the bone? He got the bone? They're all going to pick up on this. This is going to be the latest thing, right?
You know it.
This is going to be, everyone's going to now be saying the bone. It's going to become a craze, right?
It's hit or miss with the Juggalos. Sometimes we think we got it nailed to what they're going to want to see.
Yeah.
Like for the Gathering, for example, we bring one of our favorite artists to the Gathering that we grew up loving.
And then they
and watch
them
get pelted off stage.
Like, who did you bring to the Gathering that got pelted?
Too Short.
Too Short got
pelted. The legendary Too Short, man.
They hated him.
He just walked the fuck off
but
stage.
But, you know, this year... We brung our all-time favorite.
Who is that?
Ice Cube.
Oh.
And he turned it out.
Killed it.
He turned it out.
Kicked the door down with my feet. Ran down the steps and headed right into the street. Waved on a car, the driver stopped and looked at me. He got the ball. Get out, bitch! He got the ball!
Production values on your album are very good. I mean, people expect it to be raw. It's very, very well produced.
You know, we actually have one of the same producers as Kid Rock.
Why do bands not hire you to produce their album? How come you've never done any of that?
We have done some stuff
here
for underground groups.
Here and there.
But, you know, Mikey Clark is he's what makes ICP from fresh to magic.
He's like the unofficial third member of ICP, pretty much.
Is it true I was thanked on the record?
All the time.
I was
every
thanked
album,
on this album.
Every album.
Is it true I was thanked on this album, yes
absolutely.
Or no?
Yeah. You helped put us out,
you.
Man.
That's very nice of you. And you guys said recently in an interview that you don't think Robin likes you. Is that true?
What?
I didn't say that.
Yes, I'll read you the quote. Yep. Violent J said it. No.
Okay, see?
Violent J said it.
I know she likes me. She wants to get with me.
Why do you guys think... Yeah, she wants you. There's no question about
that. I think
so.
That. I mean, I'm like...
That could be the alcohol talking.
I take vibes wrong. You wouldn't have sex with Shaggy 2 Dope?
What?
You wouldn't have sex...
You see the eyes she gave me? She looked at me like,
you wouldn't have. Would you have sex?
She was like, hell yeah.
Would you have sex with Shaggy 2 Dope?
I don't know even what he looks like.
That's you know what
you're looking at me.
You're going to be in that clown makeup?
Sure.
I don't think so.
Whatever your fetish is.
Is Shaggy 2 Dope a black guy or a white guy?
He's a white guy.
He looks like T.I. though.
He looks black to me.
I'm Asian.
Are you?
No.
You should see him without the paint on. He looks just like T.I.
You look black.
You're Native American, you're claiming now?
I always assumed you were
I'm not claiming it. I am.
You're Native American?
Yeah.
You're Cherokee?
Full Cherokee?
No, not full.
Okay.
What are you really?
I just told you.
No, come on. What are you?
I'm half Polish, half Cherokee.
Are you part black?
No.
You're not?
Not that I'm aware of.
I mean, look at your skin.
I don't know my mom got with the mountain, man.
And look at your hair, even. It's like kinky. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I just thought you were black, sort
of. And he talks like a black guy.
Yeah.
I mean, that's not like wigger shit. That's
no,
black guy.
You talk like a black man.
Why? Well,
I always thought you had something black in you.
No, there's nothing in me.
Wow. Didn't you assume he was black? Violent J?
Violent J, what was that?
I always assumed it.
Yeah.
He thought he was with a black guy.
Okay. That's
Are
right.
Are you serious?
I mean,
Polish and Cherokee.
I mean,
so, see, there you go. I'm a stupid drunk.
Me too, man.
Are you going to be successful this time and stay off the booze?
I have no choice or I'll die.
No, you won't die, but
I'll live with a fucking one of those dialysis machines hooked up to me all the time. You know what I'm saying?
How old are you? Dialyze the liver.
How old am I? I'm 34. I'll be 35 in October.
That's young for cirrhosis, man.
Exactly. I told you I was drinking like 2/5 a day.
But how old were you when you started drinking?
In the womb.
Wow. Why do you think you drink so much? Were you abused?
No. I mean, I was...
Like Violent J was...
I was never sexually abused. I mean, I was like beaten and shit, you know what I'm saying?
But by your father?
By my... Well, yeah. And I got like mad like stepbrothers and like, you know what I'm saying?
Who beat the shit out of you?
All my brothers.
So do you think that's why he drinks, Violent J?
I think he's had a hard life, man.
Yeah, he has.
Well, wait a minute. Get back to somebody thinking I don't like them.
Well, what about that? You don't think Robin likes the band, right?
I think...
She's anti-Juggalo, anti-ICP. You think she's too good?
What are you talking about?
I think
it's
like... She thinks she's too intellectual for ICP.
Sometimes... It's like Weight Watchers in this bitch. You know what I'm saying?
What are you
what
talking
do you mean?
About?
I'm talking about we walk up in this bitch, I'm either fat, or I lost some weight, or I'm fat again. You know, it's just like, come on, man. You
well,
know
you have
saying?
Gained weight. That's,
yeah,
you
but,
mean, it's
you
an
know,
observation.
So what?
You know. No one's putting you down for it. I'm just wondering what's going on. I think I think it's an
are
result.
Are you saying that I'm saying these
usually,
things
usually, it's because
I think it's
because
you want to know something?
But I know you don't hate us. The other problem was that you claim... that I saw you one day in Manhattan, and I ignored you and played off like it wasn't me. Remember
right,
that?
Yeah,
not
that
true.
Happened.
Not true.
Oh, please.
See, here we go.
And I think...
That happened.
I think the weight gain is a result of your molestation. The fact that your balls were juggled at a young age.
The weight gain is a result of loving to eat snacks.
No, I think it's a protection because you don't want any of these guys coming up and grabbing your balls, so you're trying to make yourself less attractive. You're an attractive man, there's no question, but you're, you know, you're
Look,
trying to be less
weight,
sexy.
My weight means I'm more attractive.
Listen.
You know what I'm saying? Chicks love a big teddy bear.
You be careful. You be careful. Don't let it balloon up too much. Don't let it get out of control.
Yeah, it could get out of control.
That's right. Well, listen, boys, it's a big day. The Insane Clown Posse goes on stronger and better than ever. I'm happy for you guys. It's a huge success story. You worked your way up. Nobody handed you anything, and I like that. That's the American way. Am I correct?
Yes.
That's right.
Thank you.
Now, we have a new segment on our show. This is where guys come in and undress you. And then, I'm just kidding.
We do a contest of who can undress you faster.
Insane Clown Posse's new album, Bang Pow Boom, hits stores today. You know, the Black Eyed Peas have a song.
Yeah, that sucked.
Boom Pow.
Yeah. We were already working on ours when we heard that. We were like, damn.
But I can't front. I like that song.
I like it, too.
I like it, too. I think it's good.
And, you know, last time we came on the show, we made some comments about Fergie.
Right.
You know,
me too.
And I apologize for that.
Oh, no, being a method.
No, I didn't say that.
No, we didn't.
We kind of dished it out,
but she, yeah.
You dished it out, but she's not a method, is she?
She used
had
to be.
She had a she's meth a
recovered,
problem.
She's a recovered
yeah.
method.
Oh, yeah. So you like her now?
I would like to fuck out of her.
As a musician, yeah.
I'd like to see her naked.
You're not kidding. You hit that hard. Well, boys, ICP will kick off their upcoming tour September 17th in Minneapolis, Minnesota. That'll be a big date. You've been practicing the new songs, I hope.
Yeah,
the tour,
rehearsing. We're bringing the thunder this time.
You memorize
now,
all the lyrics?
Now, when you guys do a show, is
in the studio that much, you already know.
All right, okay.
Is it a big production? Do you have, like, sound and video and
we have a whole,
pyrotechnics?
Yeah.
Yeah?
We have a whole stage.
We might have to go, Robin.
Yeah.
We put the show back into the show business.
Yeah, we don't just walk back and forth rapping. We got
15 of our friends on stage.
We bring three semis, three tour buses full of crew and people, and we bring the thunder, man. That's what we're proud of.
Have you ever been asked to perform for the troops?
No, but that'd be the shit.
You would do it.
I don't think I'm allowed out of the country.
You're not. You have a lot of... You have to visit your parole officer, too, and all that? Oh, what? What do you mean, shoot?
He hasn't been visiting.
He's supposed to be out of Michigan.
Oh,
man.
What are you saying?
Oh, no.
How you going to put me on Front Street like that? Now my PA's going to hear this, and I'm going to go to fucking jail.
Well, that's why we're broadcasting from Michigan.
Hey, by the way, how are you not in jail for the breaking and entering?
Because I had a super lawyer that was down with the judge.
Wow, that's fantastic. You mean all you got was probation?
This was not breaking and entering. This is like borderline attempted murder.
Oh, so, in other words, you got out, And you
I did it overnight in jail. My lawyer bailed me out. Yeah.
Well, you're very lucky. You're very lucky.
It was a small bail somehow, too. I got real lucky.
How much was the bail?
Like 80,000, 10%.
Right. All right, listen, for additional tour dates and info, go to InsaneClownPosse.com. You boys always have your website where people can check in with you.
You know what? I was thinking they were sane, but no, they're still insane.
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah, they might be. And to purchase Violent J's book, ICP, Behind the Paint, which is where I got a lot of the facts about Violent J's molestation as a child, his stepfather grabbing his balls.
Juggling them.
Juggling his balls.
Very gingerly.
Gingerly, yes. You didn't get hard from that, did you? I'm just asking.
I'm about to puke, bro.
Me too, man. I'm like,
that wouldn't be cool. All right, listen. To purchase Violent J's book, ICP Behind the Paint, go to hatchetgear.com. So there's a lot going on, and boys, we wish you lots of success and congratulations on your new album.
Thank you.
Now, Robin, we'll be back right after these words. All right. As you know, Robin challenges me when I say Insane Clown Posse are international superstars, but they are. They are very, very wealthy young men. They have built an empire.
Well, there are plenty of wealthy people who aren't superstars.
They have sold tons of records. Yeah, I'll let the boys inform you. Tons. You know, Insane Clown Posse made $10 million last year. Look at the boys. They look great. They look great.
Hello.
They've never changed their look.
Not at all.
They stay true to that look.
Still in the makeup.
You know, a lot of people thought the makeup was a gimmick when you boys started. And that makeup is not a gimmick.
Well, it's actually just our face. And it's like, you know, the Joker and the first Batman. We got to put flesh tone paint over this to go out normally. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know why you wouldn't have it tattooed on it.
Right. Yeah, you know.
Walk around like that 24/7.
It works great at the airport. They love us there.
Boys, great to see you.
You too, man.
You know, I love that. I like the video Miracles. You took a lot of shit for that video.
We sure did. And we were serious about it. I want everybody to know that. That wasn't supposed to be funny. That was coming from the heart.
The video I'm talking about, of course, everyone has seen it. Miracles.
What are you laughing for?
Yeah, what's so funny?
So you've seen that?
What is so funny about that?
I'm going to go along with this for now.
Go along with it. These guys
everyone
put out a video.
Seen it. It's quite a controversy.
First of all, I think it's a very expensive video. It looked very rich. You guys are flying through space.
Yeah, that was really space, too, man.
You guys actually went up in space.
They actually went to space.
Yeah, that shit went cheap.
But, boys, you talk about in that song the miracle of life, the beauty that you see around you. You even describe in the song, which is my favorite passage, about how you went to feed a pelican. A fish.
Yes.
And it ate your cell phone.
It almost did.
And doesn't that say it all? Really?
Well, we're from Detroit. We don't have pelicans running around. Right. You know what I mean? Stand there in San Francisco and see a pelican, you know, about 5 feet away from you, and then actually think your cell phone is a fish and try to eat it. trips you out if you're from Detroit. We don't have pelicans with giant beaks and all that.
Your fans understand that, but someone like Robin doesn't understand.
It's unfortunate because it's beautiful.
Right.
I'm. Are they growing up? I mean, you're indicating that they have emotions I've never heard described to them or ascribed to them.
Are you getting, for lack of a better word, softer in your old age?
No, that's absolutely not.
Go ahead, man.
Go ahead.
You have to understand, that's nothing new to the juggalos that have heard us sing songs like that. I mean, you could put CDs together, full compilations, if you took all the songs we've done like that in the past.
If it's from the beginning.
You have done sensitive music before.
Deep. You know, in deep fact, songs.
People would be surprised about you guys, that they think you're just a bunch of violent thugs. But you, like you're against, you don't like Ted Nugent, for example, because he's into hunting. You don't like hunting, right?
Well, you know, people like him for his musicianship. Why does he constantly talk about hunting? He even brings out a bow and arrow on stage.
It's like, who gives a
if you're not into hunting, you know what I mean? I mean, if you're not into hunting and you're into his music and you're sitting there watching him hunt on stage and shit, it's like, relax with the hunting, man. You
know,
play some guitar, so.
That's not what got him famous.
But in Miracles, you guys, you put together a beautiful looking video and you say, listen, the world, you look at the world like an innocent child. Look at the beauty in the world. I get your music, man. I know where you're at.
You know, and then recently having kids myself, a couple
you
years ago.
You had kids?
Yes.
Jesus Christ.
We've been out here for a minute, huh?
And they're geniuses, too. But, you know, watching everything through their eyes again, is pure awesomeness. You know what I'm saying? Like a ladybug or a caterpillar, you know what I mean?
Right, you rediscover the world.
Yeah, yeah, and seeing what it means again, you know, and you get lost in the everyday shuffle of life, and then you can't express yourself right because people are so judgmental now, and especially today's age where everybody lives on the internet and nobody even leaves out of their house anymore to experience real shit, you know?
Nature, yeah.
Your fans, some of them did not understand.
Our
miracles.
Fans, yeah. I didn't hear anything bad from the Juggalo Nation.
You feel it was your critics who came down on you for this?
As usual.
Right.
Well, you probably know, really ain't our critics who are just critics in general.
You know, Robin doesn't understand.
What we discussed before was usually critics of music are failed musicians themselves.
That's
you know
true.
What I'm saying?
Robin doesn't understand the power of you guys. I mean,
I really have not had any experience of this Juggalo
Nation.
Do you
want to know what? Do you want to know what, though?
What?
Hey, Jay is a recently single guy.
For Robin?
Well, what's he just up? Had a kid. What happened to
not
the woman?
Yes, he's not older.
He dumped his wife.
We ain't been here in a few years, man.
Violent J, you dumped your wife shortly after she had the kid. What happened? Did you get turned off to her pregnancy?
Sure.
What the fuck happened?
Elvis?
There?
What's going on?
Yeah, what are you, Elvis?
No, we were together for a long time, you know what I mean? It's just that it wasn't working out on that level.
What happened?
I mean?
You're an attractive man. I imagine she loved you.
Was it the road? Temptation?
Did you get turned off to her?
No, man. You know, it just wasn't. I didn't
couldn't fuck her anymore.
I found it impossible to make her happy anymore. You know what I mean?
Is that true? You mean you were in love with her, but she was never happy?
Yeah.
Why is that? What do you think went wrong?
I think that you know, I met her when
she
was
woke
young.
Up? No.
You know what I'm saying?
How young was she? She woke up.
She was 19 when I met her.
No
it
kidding.
It was 8 years ago, though.
I see.
You know, and I just think that. You know, but the bottom line is, I consider myself one of the hottest free agents in the game right now.
Are you a player?
Absolutely.
You are?
Absolutely.
You're out there fucking like a rabbit.
Right now?
Yeah.
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 I got a lot of built up aggression, you know what I'm saying? But you have to understand, like, you know, I was good.
You ever fuck a girl with the clown makeup on?
So many times, brother.
Did you ever fuck your wife with the clown makeup on?
No.
Early on,
maybe
come
early,
on.
Maybe early. Yeah. It wasn't like I was at home and I put it on before I fucked her.
Do chicks dig that? I mean, when you have the makeup
on? Well, sometimes it's a convenience thing. You know what I'm saying? You're backstage, you're in the bus,
see,
you're about to
pull out stuff I can't be doing. You know, I could never do that. You know what I'm
you
saying?
You fuck like, your wife with
oh,
the
you
clown
never,
makeup
on? No.
I'm saying, like, you know what I'm saying? Like a backstage situation. You know, it's so dirty and nasty. You know what I'm saying? It's like, oh, I could it just.
See, people think of you as a guy who would just fuck anywhere. And
I mean,
I
could in a lot of places, just not like, you know, whatever.
Backstage,
that's sick, man. You know how much nuts on that couch and like how much ass juice and balls been dragged by the sweat. You know what I'm saying? How horrible is that, man?
Yeah, so Violent shit, that is disgusting, right? To be backstage and fuck
on,
a girl.
No, I mean, that's just me being a germ freak. You know what I'm saying? I've been saying that I don't make a practice of it.
But you fuck girls with the clown makeup on.
One time in my life. It was
that's
the worst experience of my life.
Why? Why was it bad?
Because the broad wouldn't stop staring at my face. I'm not going to lie to you, dog. Check it out. I'm hitting her, right? Just normal.
Yeah.
And she's just staring at my face. You know what I'm saying? Just staring at my face.
I get it.
Not even making a noise. Nothing. I'll turn a bitch out. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And she's just staring at my face.
Wow.
I'm like, all right, cool. Let me try flipping this broad over. You know what I'm saying? So I flip her over. And sure, start staring at my face again. You know, like an owl turning his head. I try to put my leg arm before him against the back of her neck. And somehow just turns around and looks at my face. I quit.
Shaggy,
I was like, you know, I'm done. I'm out of here.
Shaggy, you married now?
No.
No.
Well, I legally I am, but no.
Right.
So you're both single.
No, I'm
what
not
happened,
single.
What happened with your marriage?
I'm really not.
What happened with your marriage?
It just dissolved.
Right.
You know,
what happened?
You know, kind of probably the same thing that happened to yours. You know what I'm saying? Just long hours of work. Just connection wasn't there.
Little, right.
You know, my former alcohol problem had a little something to do with it. You know what I'm saying? A lot
sure.
of shit. You know,
you've been sober? You've been staying clean?
Yeah. No
okay.
doubt.
Violent and, Jay, you're not sober, are you?
Huh?
What?
What is this?
Are you boys still close off, you know? Or do you have to stay away from him? Are you guys like the Beatles? After
chill,
a while,
man.
they didn't really hang out.
I see this guy every day, man.
Every day.
You're so blessed in that fashion.
Every day of my life.
Every day, we talk constantly.
Because you guys get a kick out of each other.
Of course.
And we're the only ones that truly, fully, truly understand each other.
Right. Thank God we don't have to go through what we go through alone.
Yeah.
We have each other, you know?
And it's cool. It's not like, you know, like 15 of us in a band. You know what I'm saying?
We just fallouts happening everywhere.
It's more like a brothership than it is.
Are you sick and tired of the industry not giving you any respect? Man, you guys made 10. What did you make? 10 million last year?
We're so done giving a shit.
You don't give a shit.
You know what I'm saying?
You don't care.
No. We're just doing our thing, man.
If we were respected and loved like that, we wouldn't be what we are. We wouldn't be the most hated band in the world.
But don't you think you should be on the Grammys? Seriously. Wouldn't you like some sort of acceptance? Seriously, come on.
I don't give a fuck about a Grammy. This honest.
Right.
I would like to be invited. You know what I'm saying? I think we should be able to be recognized to be able to go. Not invited as like a nominee, but just to be able
just to
go.
Be in the audience.
Right. Yeah. Like, I don't know why.
It's kind of crazy. You know what I'm saying? What is it? 2 weeks ago in Detroit, they did like the big Detroit Music Awards, and they gave us the Distinguished Lifetime Music Award.
Really?
Detroit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know what
is
I'm saying?
Is that true?
It's a huge honor for us. I mean, they had the video screen
you
showing.
You don't believe it, Robin?
I want to see the award.
Oh, it was devastating.
I'm like that with the president. I need to see some.
You're like a birther. You want to see.
Robin used to like us? He's hating today, man. What's going on over here?
He doesn't believe that you guys are big stars. Meanwhile, I'm going to tell you this. I bet you there's a lot of record companies out there.
You should go out with this guy for one night, I'm telling you. You're single, right?
Why are you trying to hook me up with Robin?
Why not? I'm with it.
Why don't you get with her?
Oh, my God.
So say, you're single, right?
Because she ain't having it. I mean, I would love you to go out
with Violent J?
In the makeup?
No. He's clean. You wouldn't take her out in your makeup.
Either or. You don't care.
Would you go out with Violent J?
I don't think so.
Oh,
why? Because he's overweight?
No. That has
That's
nothing
muscle.
To do with it.
Absolutely. Pure.
What's going on with your weight? I'm worried about you.
Oh, here we go.
What's going on, man? Seriously.
Man, I represent fat kid love, man. You know what I'm saying?
I used to worry about it.
I don't really know. I really don't even know. But honestly.
What are you eating that? Are you eating good food or are you eating?
I'm eating hella bad snacks at night.
What do you like to eat? What happened?
Double cheesy cheeseburgers.
Right.
And pizza. And I love to, you know, eat good tasting food. I'll admit it. But, you know, honestly, I'm content with that. I mean, I'm honest with you. I'll be honest with you about everything.
Right.
I'm content with who I am. I love who I am right now these days.
Do you think it turns your wife off, though? Because sometimes if you get very heavy, a woman just can't fucking stand it.
It's possible. It's possible. You know, my ex-girl was, like, extremely beautiful.
Were you in love with her?
Yeah.
So did it break your heart when she said, that's it, it's over?
She didn't. We just mutually, you know, we still raise the kids together, though. We're good friends.
But did the clown cry? Come on.
There's a man behind the
times.
You have cried.
I got a big heart.
You do?
Yeah.
That's what I know about you guys. That you do have big hearts.
Come on, I'd be fronting if I said, I don't cry, you know.
Right. So, what Robin and the rest of the industry doesn't understand.
I really need to know is what is their business?
Their business is music? What are you talking about?
Man, we dabble in so much shit, it's ridiculous.
See, tell us. You know what I'm saying?
What do you do? Crazy shit.
Let's see. You know, we run a record company, underground music, you know, an alternative to what's out there in the world, you know, an alternative to the mainstream.
You're doing what everyone talks about doing. They all say, oh, this should be an alternative. You're trying to keep that going.
And, you know, outside view, looking at what we do, most of the artists on our label have face paint of some sort.
Really?
Into an outside view, it looks like it's all the same, but to the Juggalo Nation, it's so much more than that. It's so much more special than that. It's that every artist on our label has a character, a persona, a bio of interest. You know what I mean?
How do you find an artist for your label? Do you get tapes submitted?
Yeah,
if I want to become a...
It's a very small roster. You know what I'm saying? It's built over many years. You know, and then every once in a while, like our most recently signees are called the Dayton Family. And they're like some cast from back in the day that we love from Flint, Michigan. You know what I'm saying?
Could you turn these bitches out and make some coin with them?
They got a video out right now called Cocaine.
Right.
Now think about this for a minute. The video's called Cocaine, and it is like an expensive video with no. This has a point.
Right.
It's an expensive video with no indication at all of trying to get it on MTV or BET.
There's no more cocaine all over the place.
There's cocaine flying all through the video. There's, I mean, like...
No naked bitches, nothing. Just
no naked
cocaine.
Bitches, just cocaine flying everywhere. And it's... The point is...
What is the point?
Quality for underground. Just because it's underground doesn't mean it's bootleg and scratchy.
I always like your videos. They're good quality videos.
Yeah, but it's not for the mainstream system. It's for the underground. It's made and intended for that. And it's quality shit that could be in the mainstream, but just because it's underground doesn't mean it's got to be bootleg looking or sound.
Robbie doesn't understand. You have 30 employees working for you, right?
I saw that they have an entourage of sorts with them today.
Yeah, you have an entourage. You have, you guys personally made $10 million last year, didn't you?
Well, that's what they say, but I'm not going to turn it down. It sounds pretty dope. Right.
You didn't make $10
million? Hopefully I'll make another $10 million this year.
Not even close. But that seems to be the figure everybody runs with. So, hey, if somebody's saying that about us, not like we're quick to check them on that. If
but you're millionaires, right?
I'm not a millionaire. I don't have $1 million.
Where do they live? How do they live?
I guess you're right, Robin. They aren't successful. But I thought you guys, how many albums have you sold?
A lot.
In the millions.
Yeah, like 10 million probably.
10 million. I mean, a lot of record companies would love to have you guys on their label, I would think.
Do you own your rights?
We to all but like 3 or 4 of our records, something like that. Yeah. Yeah,
we've done stuff with major labels before. All that shit. And it's always hell, man.
We would never sign with a major again just because it's just how we do things.
Right.
It's how we do it. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody else telling us how to do it or how we can or can't do
and
it.
And nobody knows our audience like we do, you know?
Well, maybe you need someone to tell you what to do. You're not making that much money.
We're very, very, you know, money is a secret issue.
It is? You want to feel like you're part of the Juggalo Nation. If they know you have all this money, it's going to ruin your whole relationship.
I could be like, hey, you want to go ride in my car right quick? You know what I'm saying? You want to jump in my Escalade? It's on my wrist. You know what I'm saying? Come on, you know?
Boys, what do you mean in your music when you say scientists are lying motherfuckers? What are we talking about?
I'll tell you what we mean by that.
Yeah.
Is scientists sometimes kill the freshness of belief of both, first of all, religions, you know what I mean?
Right.
Scientists come and disprove everything, you know? There was no Noah's Ark. There was no this or that, you know?
So that's religion not magic. Is good.
You know, the Northern Lights aren't magic. The Northern Lights in reality are, you know, scientists give you some stupid explanation for what it is.
Gaseous.
Sometimes they kill the fun of belief and freshness, you know?
But don't you guys want to know the
not
truth?
Not necessarily religion, but like, you know, just like, you know what I'm saying? The best way is just like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, why do you need to know? It's like, all right, how do magnets work? Why? Why?
You know, you don't like knowing what a magnet is?
No, I know what a magnet is. Come on, I'm not retarded. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know how a magnet works.
You stick it to metal and it sticks.
But you probably like your computer. That's from science.
No, I don't like my computer.
You hate it.
I got a laptop. I've been on it maybe like 5 times and I've had it for a year.
But you did like your
Facebook.
Cell phone.
I hate my fucking cell phone. I just now started Twitter, like, what is it, like 5 days ago I sent 2 tweets. I don't know how to do it and fuck this phone. Give me one of those AARP certified phones with a big screen and big finger thing, you know what I'm saying?
But Chris Rock does a routine. He uses the N-word when he does it, but he says, I'll quote him, "Niggers love not to know." Do you ever hear that routine? And he does this whole thing about black, he talks about there's a diversity in the black community and how he uses the N-word. I don't
Yeah, if you want to hide your money from a N-word, you hide it in a book.
Yeah, right.
Because you have to have a find.
So when you guys say scientists, I mean, come on, you can't be for real in a sense.
But sometimes, you know, they kill the party of imagination and fun. Like when I was a kid, they couldn't tell you how pyramids were made. I don't think.
That's right.
But now they
really still don't know.
Now they tell you, though. Well, here's how, you know, they used to say there's no man-made way possible how they made Stonehenge. We can't explain it. But then here comes scientists. You know.
I know who knows how pyramids were made. John Travolta knows.
He sure does. He's a Scientologist.
Yes.
Sounds like you boys are very religious.
No.
It sounds like you have found religion. Between miracles, the song, between, you know, talking about the miracle of life.
I think we respect religion, but we're not religious. We don't live a religious life.
Right.
We don't read the Bible. We don't go to church. I couldn't tell you if we're Christian or anything. I just know that, I don't even know what the difference is between a Catholic and a Christian and a Muslim. I don't know, and I don't really want to know.
Like reading books, or does that ruin everything, too?
I read a lot of books. Shit.
What? When you're taking a shit, you read a book.
Yeah, that's my reading time.
I read lots of books, lots of books.
I read till my legs fall asleep.
What book are you reading now, Violent J?
Well, I read wrestling books, people's autobiographies and stuff like that. And
you
a lot
love
of musicians'
wrestling.
Books.
What type of weed are you smoking these days?
You know, I stopped smoking because when we record an album, I don't want to smoke because it makes my voice hurt, you know what I mean?
Right.
And so I stopped smoking right now, but, you know, I'm an avid super weed smoker like crazy.
Right.
Now,
Shaggy can't.
You don't do...
I don't smoke weed. Yeah. I never have. I just don't like it. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
Well,
When I was a kid, I smoked weed a few times, and then as an adult, I smoked a few times, and last time I smoked weed on the road, I smoked a blunt and made me throw up in my bunk. You know what I'm saying?
Boys, are you being sued by Tila Tequila?
Nah. No.
You are not.
What, for what?
Well, I'll tell you
she
what.
She said she was going to sue you, but it never happened. Yeah.
How could she sue you? I mean,
she got hit in the face with a rock?
You boys every year have your Juggalo convention, and you lose money on that, though. This year you were proud you only lost $15,000 on it, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Which is great.
Gathering of the Juggalos.
Because to pay $15,000 for that to happen, for that awesomeness, to give 10,000 Juggalos that experience
right.
was something we do every year all the time. That was a
why did Tila Tequila, how did she even end up on
at
your tour?
Easy. Yeah. Easy. We figured, she had a song out called I Wanna Fuck the DJ.
Right.
She got famous because she's hot.
Right, she
right.
is hot.
Right, right.
She gets naked on stage and shit. I figured, what better for the gathering than hot ass Tila Tequila getting up on stage singing about wanting to fuck the DJ? I thought it would get over.
It was all part of like a ladies' night type deal too. It was Lil Kim, Tila Tequila, and a couple you know independent girl rappers.
So you guys contacted her.
It was all part of a whole girls' night type deal, you know.
And so you guys contacted her and said, "Hey, we have a good idea here. I think my fans would embrace you because you're hot." You'll come out there, wear something hot, and you'll do this song.
Figured it would work. Did it seem like on paper that would work?
Sounds like a plan.
I would like
to. She got paid in advance.
She did?
It was good, yeah.
You guys paid her?
Yeah, mm-hmm. She...
What do you have to pay a Tila Tequila? Not much.
But then she went on Twitter, and she was saying, you know, she was spelling clown with a K, and that was...
She was disrespecting you.
Irking the Juggalos a little bit. You know. They didn't like that. And she wasn't a Juggalo, but she was posting things on the web like, hey, I'm a Juggalo. You know, Juggalos were like, no, you ain't. You know what I mean?
Right.
And she was being disrespectful a little bit. But we asked Juggalos in our seminar earlier that day. We were like, look, we know the word is she's going to get booed.
Yeah, everybody was like, she's about to get it.
We would like everybody to be cool from our opinion. Of course, we don't control the Juggalos. Right. The Juggalos control us.
People think you have a hypnotic trance over
That's
your
ridiculous.
Fans.
That's the other way around.
Yeah. Right.
Right there is a good example that we don't control.
You guys have seminars? I caught you said you have seminars.
Well, you know, we have like, we get up and answer questions and talk about what we're doing this year. And
we'll have like a whole, like anybody that's there, you know what I'm saying? We'll have like scheduled seminars during the day.
How many people show up for a seminar?
Oh, man, probably like...
That's about who it is, really. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. For us, probably like 1,000.
1,000 people stand there and they ask questions.
At least, you know, it's as big as many people that can fit in that area.
And so Tila Tequila goes up on stage. She got, from what I read anyway, you can tell me the truth here, she was pelted with bags of urine.
See, I didn't see, I was
feces?
Right there, man. I was right there, and I didn't see no shit or piss.
You didn't?
I didn't actually see. I seen rocks.
Right.
I ain't gonna hold you up.
Right.
I was standing, but I didn't actually see her get hit. You know what I'm saying? I seen, cause I heard him hitting the top of the, it was like a metal roof on top of like the pavilion, and she had security in front of her, and I seen them getting lit up. You know what I'm saying? But I didn't actually see her getting lit up.
Right, so you didn't even see that.
And then they were trying to pull her on stage, and she was like, nah, I'm strong. Right, you know what I'm saying? Pull
the
titties out.
She wouldn't get off the stage.
You know what I'm saying?
She wouldn't get off the stage, and in order to win over the crowd, she revealed her breasts to the Juggalos, and the Juggalos got even more incensed.
And maybe that's where the shit started flying, and I don't know.
Explain the Juggalo mentality to me. When a woman takes her top off for me, the shit stops flying, and I want to, I mean, she's doing what I want.
She gets your attention.
Right. I think she should have caught the hint right from the rip. They didn't, you know, you can tell it wasn't going right.
But you boys know, sometimes you go out there, the crowd's against you,
and you can
win them over.
There was
no winning.
No, man.
You sensed there was no.
She was like, she kept saying, and you heard her, she kept saying, what was she saying? I ain't no whack bitch.
Yeah, she was like, fuck that.
I'm not no pussy. I'm not going to run.
Yeah,
and
like,
that was making it worse.
Fuck yeah, I'm up here. Fuck yeah, I ain't going nowhere. I'm just like, all right, man.
And she's taunting the crowd, right?
Basically, yeah.
And, you know, when you receive the indication, the Juggalos don't want you on there. And then when she took off her top, I think it further... pissed off the Juggalos, like,
well,
come on, man.
When your security guy gets hit in the head with a rock, that's time to leave the stage. I would think. You know, and then she skedaddled to her, like, her dressing room was right there, and then it almost got overran. And then me, And one of the guys from Twist, they had a group on a label. You know what I'm saying? Yes. We like kind of dispersed the crowd.
Right.
And I went in there, and man, she looks weird in real life, that broad Tila Tequila. She's like this tall, and she has a chipmunk face, and her titties are way too big for her body. Just looks like a fucking alien. But anyhow, got her out safely. You know what I'm saying? You weren't sending her a look, maybe because her face was swollen up and she was bleeding, but.
Oh, God, what are you talking about?
But, man, she was an odd looking spectacle.
What, you know,
she looked a lot better on TV.
Would it have been funny if you guys, while you were trying to talk to her, started throwing things at her?
Oh, I just went in there and started whipping shit at her.
Yeah.
You know, I want to say that we don't apologize on behalf of the Juggalos or not like that. Juggalos do what they do, and we represent Juggalos.
Well, the Juggalos.
I mean, she had ample time to bounce before shit got out of control. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
that's the bottom line. She chose to stay up there and
but
did
the,
what she did.
But the Juggalos really shouldn't throw things at people. Have the Juggalos ever turned on you guys and thrown things?
I've been hitting the head so hard with shit that it knocked me the fuck out on stage on my feet. I broke my neck on stage. Straight. I got plastic discs, cadavers, metal plates, all that good shit.
You got dead people's parts in your
straight
neck?
Straight up.
Wait a second. You're telling me they took the dead...
cadaver disc. Cadavers. You know, cadaver. Cadaver. You know, on the back of your license or whatever, you know, the motherfuckers that get shit taken out of them. I got some of that in my knee and in my neck. And
no
all
shit.
Yeah.
You got another person's body. Did you ever feel overtaken by that person?
You know, sometimes I wake up sleepwalking at night and, you know.
No, you never have. Is it weird to you to have a dead person's neck?
At first, I thought about it, but I'm used to it.
Right, yeah. Hey.
What are you going to do? It's either that or having
now.
A broken neck.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And what broke your neck? The force of the rock knocking into your head?
No, I actually broken it twice. I've broken it once from wrestling professionally, and I've broken it doing a show at The Gather. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And the second time when I broke it, I shattered four of my vertebrae. You know, finished the show, though.
Wow.
And then went out for a couple months, and then my wife, you know, she was like, because my arm went paralyzed, you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
She was like, you got to go to the doctor. So I went in, he put me in surgery.
Wow.
But you know what I'm saying? We get it.
Any idea who's.
They don't turn on us like that, but you know what I'm saying? We get in the face constantly with shit.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Did you ever try to find out whose body parts you have inside of you?
Well, yeah, I'm going to scan them and see if they, you know, they got a seal.
Is there a name?
Sometimes it's a name.
I got an ACL, a dead ACL up in my knee, too.
Yeah, right. That's how they do it. Yeah, that's awesome. So you're saying a woman should kind of be able to read the vibe of the crowd.
There's no question in my mind. There's no question in my mind that she knew way in advance, right when she stepped on that stage, I would say 30 seconds into her set, that, you know, shit wasn't cool.
Violent J, did you try to fuck her?
I didn't get a chance to even see her or meet her. I was doing something else at the time. I just heard about it, you know.
Right.
It's unfortunate, but, you know, like I said, we stand behind what the Juggalos do. The Juggalos are like, fuck her, we're like, fuck her, too.
Right, I ain't gonna apologize.
The dudes were throwing, according to her, were throwing huge stone rocks at my face, beer bottles that slit my eye open, almost burnt my hair on fire because they threw firecrackers on stage.
Well, that's funny. If you keep staying up there, eventually they're gonna shoot her, probably. You don't get off the stage, man.
You got in show
back
business.
Back in the day, see, I had my back burnt by jumping. You don't remember those jumping jacks when you were a kid? You let them go, bzzz. Like, we did this bit, like, where we fall on stage, and right where we fell, somebody threw a fucking jumping jack. And I was trying to play it off like it wasn't burning, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
For the show. And I still got, like, a divot in my back from that, I think.
Jesus Christ, it's a hell of a way to make a living.
I don't know if I'd want to be the leader of the Juggalos.
Right, it's tough, I tell you. But the Juggalos are following you, and you say you put on the show, you lost $15,000, but it doesn't bother you.
That's investment of mine.
Boys, let me, of course.
How long can this go on?
Forever.
Forever. For real, ever. I predict it right now. We'll be here forever. Unless something happens.
Come on, what was the first time we were on here?
We were
in effect before the first time we ever came on here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm going to say you guys have the longest running act in show business almost. I mean, like, I'm thinking about everyone's come and gone. You guys are still in business.
And the shit we have planned, the shit we have coming,
business, but
that we can't even tell y'all about. That shit.
Why can't you tell us what you're up to? What are you planning?
Because we can't give away the biggest shit we got planned for the future.
What is the biggest thing you got coming up?
You know,
the people now.
Well, we have a new album we're working on, in the tactics we're going to do to promote it and the style we're going to do it. I can't say it.
See Insane Clown Posse tomorrow night at 7 at Gramercy Theater.
Oh, all right.
Stay for the after party at midnight at Rocks Off Concert Cruise at the Skyport Marina. See the kinds of things that are going on? Don't miss ICP at the Bamboozle Festival this Sunday.
Very rare appearance for us, by the way. We don't do festivals.
Why not?
Because we don't usually subject it. audience to our shit.
Yeah, the reason I invited too, you know.
And you know, we know are what we do is a rare product. We don't like to open for anybody or do anything like that.
So why are you doing this?
Well, it was kind of an honor issue. We were really honored that they asked us, you know, and we were kind of surprised by it, and we couldn't believe they did, you
it's
know?
Not, it's not a touring festival.
Are you afraid, though, are you afraid you're going to be up in a different audience from the Juggalos, right, and they are going to do to you?
That's really what we wanted to do it for, is to get out there and represent. We haven't done it in so long to get up there and do what we do in front of, and hit the Faygo on everybody that don't see it coming. It's just exciting.
Who else is on the tour? Who has invited you to this tour? I mean,
it's not a tour. It's just a show. But it's got like Motley Crue on it, Lil Wayne, all types of people. All
right. Yeah, it's a real, real big deal. The real reason we did it, and I know a lot of Juggalos even wonder why we did it. The real reason we did it is for the story. We just want to get out there and do something like that.
Something
one time,
different.
You know? Yeah, something different.
Something's going to happen for me.
You're putting yourselves in danger in a sense because you have to go win over the crowd. This isn't a built-in slam dunk.
Right, and that's what bothers me the most about how hated we are. We know we have a different product, but we're not on MTV.
Right.
You know, you don't have to sit through our videos while you're waiting for your favorite video. You don't have to sit through our performance to get blasted with Faygo and other debris while you're waiting for your favorite band. We don't open for
How
nobody.
Many songs are you planning on doing in front of this crowd, this
We're
new
doing
crowd.
A 50-minute set.
Ooh. 50 minutes.
We're bringing the thunder. We're going to bring the motherfucking thunder.
Don't miss ICP at the Bamboozle Festival this Sunday at the New Meadowlands Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. You ever get tired of all this shit? Do you ever think about hanging up the clown makeup? Seriously. And just saying, fuck it.
And do what?
I don't want to sound like...
I got too many felonies, man. I can't do nothing else.
How many felonies do you have?
I don't
seriously.
Know, I think five.
Five felonies. Five,
something like that.
Is that right?
So it's either this or jail.
Right. You know what I'm saying? This is great.
What are your five felonies?
I don't know. One was like breaking and entering. One's like weapons charges, home invasion, assault with deadly weapon.
You are a bad motherfucker.
Actually, all types of shit. Yeah.
Found you. You ever scared of him? Seriously.
Sometimes. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes something shocking happens.
He keeps me under control, though, man. You know what I'm saying? He does.
Thank
He's like
God.
A big brother. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. What shocks you about him? Because you think you know him, and then all of a sudden he goes out and does something crazy?
You know, honestly, for the last couple of years, he's been so on point, it's fucking ridiculous.
Right.
When
was your last home invasion?
That was the last charge.
Oh, yeah, that was like, I don't know, like 3 years ago.
3 years ago?
Oh, my God,
four
just that
ago?
Recent?
Maybe four, no, 4 years ago. 4 years ago.
I mean, here you
know,
are a famous
like
guy. You
4 years
a,
ago.
You got a
I mean,
career.
You
what
know,
were you doing
not,
a home
it's
invasion?
It's just like I'm fucking. You know what I'm saying? There was a reason to the rhyme to the reason.
Why
you know
did you
saying?
Do the home invasion? It had a great career going. I mean, you could have jeopardized the whole thing.
Well, the whole thing is, you know, you don't think you're going to get caught.
Somebody
with the intent of getting caught.
Somebody stole something from his house.
Right.
We heard word through the street where it was, and he went to
some guy
it.
Stole from like my mom's house back in the day, you know what I'm
right,
saying? And
right.
It turned up like on like some internet shit or something like that, and I heard through
you went to reclaim your stuff. It's kind of like what OJ got there.
Didn't you see what happened to OJ?
That's what my lawyers are calling it. You know what I'm saying?
It
was like around the same time. You know what I'm saying? They're like, oh, OJ. I'm like, yeah, hi, real funny. I'm facing 3 to 30 fucking years here and laugh. You know what I'm saying?
So how did you get off?
I had a super lawyer that knew the judge and all that.
Yeah.
That always helps.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And Violent J, you're probably like, you know, we got a fucking act here. You can't be going in a home
you
invading.
You know, probation is the motherfucker. Because that prevents us from going to Canada.
It's the worst.
That prevents us from going, you know, out of the country.
Yeah, it's like so many Juggalos in Canada. Like, what's up, man? Come you guys don't never come up here?
And just as we're about to go again, he gets in trouble. You know what I'm saying?
Were you nervous when you met him and said, hey, I'm going to throw in with this guy? But he is fucking out. I know, but he must have been. You probably said, Jesus Christ, I don't know. Like a bang on this guy. He's fucking crazy.
No, man, that's my brother.
Right.
You don't question family like that. You just roll with it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
we got something really special going on.
Shit happens, but home invasions don't just happen.
I mean, they do every day.
What was the assault
about?
Charge?
Somebody's got to do them.
What was the assault charge?
I'm that guy.
What was the assault charge?
There was assault with a deadly weapon. You know, basically, I stuck the guy up. You know, what are you going to do?
I don't know what you do. What do you mean you stuck the guy up? How does that work? On the streets?
Yeah, shit. No, I came to his house and got my shit back. You know what I'm saying?
Again, somebody had your crap.
That was the same dude.
Same dude. Yeah. Oh,
but he pulled a shotgun up on me. You know what I'm saying? Then ran out of his own house. How are you going to do that? You know what I'm saying?
Well, he pulled a shotgun out because you were in his home.
Put a gun in his face. You know, whatever.
It's well, wait, wait. Explain this.
This was a few years back.
I'm fascinated. You broke into the house.
I didn't break into the house. That would be breaking and entering. This is home invasion.
All right. Okay. All right, I'm sorry.
He answered the door.
I didn't mean to disparage you.
He answered the door.
He answered the door.
The breaking and entering was from 10 years ago.
Yeah, that's from when I was a kid. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Yeah, right. I broke into a corn island for to get some free hot dogs.
Big deal.
Right.
You're a bad criminal. You always get caught.
Well, nah. I mean, I only got caught for some of this shit. But, you know, hey, when I was young, I used to be a hustler like a motherfucker. But, you know, basically, all right, went to dude's house, walked up there, you know what I'm saying, answered the door, let me get my shit, walked in, pulled the shot, he ran out, got the shit, bounced out. Wow. Police showed up at the other spot I went to jail.
So Shaggy,
condensed version.
Right.
Yeah. Sometimes, you know, people don't realize you're a white guy, right? They don't realize that.
I mean, I...
Well, looking at him, you can
tell. You know what I mean. When they hear you on the radio and stuff, they think you're a black dude, right?
No.
They don't?
I don't know.
I think you are sometimes. You know what I mean? Because you got the whole thing, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Even though you know what I'm saying, you got.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
All right.
You're down with that. It's unbelievable. Are you mixed?
No.
Really?
No.
Your parents still alive?
No.
What happened to them?
Did you kill them?
No.
Did they try to run you into a lake?
My biological dad, I don't know, he died years ago from I don't know what. And then my mother recently passed like a year and a half ago from brain cancer.
Were you sad or would you?
Yeah, of course I was sad, man. Yeah,
you had a relationship with her.
Well, I did, and like I was on the outs with her, but then when she got sick, I was cool with her. But right. She went so quick. Once she found out she was sick, it was like 2.5 months, you know what I'm saying? We're out in L.A. shooting a movie, and then I found out, so I had to fly home.
Do you know how your dad died, or you don't even know?
Nah, he didn't even have a doctor's record. That motherfucker was, like, he was just stupid. I didn't really know him, you know what I'm saying?
He was a bad dude.
Nah, he was just sat at home and just didn't do shit, I guess.
Yeah, right. He wasn't really motivated.
Nah.
And he didn't come to visit you either.
Nah.
Is that why you turned to a life of crime? You didn't have any role models?
I don't live a life of crime, man.
No, when you did when you were a kid.
Freshness.
No, you had a life of crime when you were young. You would break in.
Get money.
Get money, right.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I mean, why else would anybody turn to crime to get money, right?
Right.
Why else would you do crime?
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, love of crime's a passion.
All right, well, I never did a crime of passion. I called a domestic violence charge.
How would you decide where to break in? Like, how would you size up someone and size up a house when you were a kid and you were doing break-in?
Are you a kid? Because you would just, like, know that, like, someone nice would be there. You just, like, go by there a bunch of times. You'd know the schedule of people leaving in the cars and whatnot. You know what
I'm
saying?
Right, right, right. You'd see they had something good.
Yeah.
What's
or
the best
you just
thing?
Like growing the crew, people just run and grab what you can and run out. They're only going to grab one motherfucker, you know?
Right. What's the best thing you ever stole? I mean,
thing I ever stole?
Yeah, like, yeah. Biggest item, biggest
where'd
ticket
you get the
item.
Most money
I mean, biggest
for?
Item, of course, would probably be a car, but, you know, biggest item worth? Shit, I don't know, man. We had so many.
What's a good store?
There's
so many hustles.
Jewelry store hustles used to be good.
Really? You don't get caught? Don't they have cameras? What do you do?
I mean, this is like back in like the early 90s, and they had cameras, but you know what I'm saying? It's not like you would like be a repeat offender at the same store. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Because, you know, they'd have all like, the silver racks up on the counter, so somebody distracted you, just clear that silver rack out and just walk out. You know what I'm saying?
Violent shit's like, what the fuck?
I'm hearing some of this for the first time. I'm like, jewelry store? What the fuck?
Did you ever feel bad stealing? Or
no, no, no. Because I would never steal, like, really from, like, well, number one, I would never steal from, like, you know, like small mom-and-pop stores. You know what I'm saying? People that were breaking their back and
just
shit.
Just big stores.
Just the big ones. The chains.
You know what I'm saying? Part, that, where they equal then people get stealing shit into the price and all that anyhow. So I'm the reason why the cost would go up on stuff.
Were you ever like Robin Hood? Did you ever give to the poor or nothing?
Hell no.
Hell no.
He was the poor.
Exactly.
Giving.
I was giving to my pocket.
But look how upset you got.
I was giving what I had to make us happy because he was working. You know what I'm saying? I was working too.
But look how upset you got when someone stole from you. You went to try and retrieve
it. But it wasn't
yourself.
From me.
Well, it was from your mother.
Well, it was technically from my brother, but he was living with my mother.
Right. So
right,
I mean,
the house got left.
So you don't like people who steal. You go and say, give me my shit back.
But see, I was
but that's
there
the game
necessity.
Of crime.
Exactly.
That's the game of crime. That's,
exactly.
If you get caught, you're
see,
slipping.
See, my kids,
you know?
If I find out my kids were, like, fucking around stealing from stores or anything, I would whip them senseless because they don't need to. I give them anything they need. You know what I'm saying?
You had motivation. You had reason.
Right. Yeah, right. I didn't have no money. What are you going to do? Get that money.
Boys, it's always fascinating talking to you. Your lives have been one big mess, and I love it. Well, anyway, the Tila Tequila controversy, there's always controversy surrounding you and the Juggalos, but you continue to persevere. You continue to go on. You say, fuck the critics. Fuck them all. You want to take some phone calls real quick? And then,
are there Juggalos on the phone?
It's hot in the studio right now with Mike E. Clark, son.
Here we go. Let's go to Jim. Jim, you're on the air with Insane Clown Posse tomorrow night at 7 at Gramercy Theater. Stay for the after party with the boys at midnight at Rocks Off Concert Cruise at the Skyport Marina. They'll party with you. If you're lucky, they'll beat the shit out of you. And don't miss ICP at the Bamboozle Festival, which is a very controversial appearance. First time the boys have gone outside the Juggalos.
The way I understand it, tomorrow's show and the after party are both sold out. Right. But it's our first time back in New York City in, like, honestly, time, like man. 8 years or 10 years or something.
Does it feel good to be back in New York?
Come on, man. Just to be back here on the show.
A lot of fun. It's good to see you, boys.
So great, man.
I thought you guys got in Hollywood. You don't even come in here anymore. Don't miss ICP at the Bamboozle Festival this Sunday, Robin, at the new Meadowlands Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Uh-huh. And check out ICP's pay-per-view. JCW wrestling events at InsaneClownPosse.com. The boys are involved in that. Jim, go ahead real quick with ICP.
Hey now, Howard. What's up?
Hey now.
ICP.
You're right.
Let's have a serious conversation. When are you guys going to fucking kill yourself?
Is it the, you know, just like we were talking about.
I called you last time, motherfucker. My douche.
Oh, this guy, the same guy that called us last time.
This is the same guy from eight years ago.
You know, it's like I was just saying, though. We don't subject what we do to people that don't want to see it. You have to look for ICP. So what is it, what's this guy's name?
Jim.
Jim, what is it that about us that bothers you? What is it that's being crammed on your face about us?
What bothers me is that my douchebag son listens to you.
You're a douchebag, son.
Your son's a douchebag.
What a great guy, my douchebag son. My douchebag son. Picture that. You know what I'm saying?
Are you jealous that ICP has a relationship with your son?
Right.
He ain't my son. He's my motherfucker.
How does it feel that we have a bigger influence on your son than you do?
Listen, none of your fucking
Jigaboo
fans listen to Howard, so I don't even know.
This guy's a bigot.
Juggalo.
No wonder why your son's a
Juggalo.
Listen, buddy, you're making a fool of your fucking self.
Is this guy for real, or is he like some kind of plant?
I think he believes in scientists, this guy. I know him. You believe in scientists?
He can't be real.
All right, let's go to Andy. Andy, go ahead.
Be real.
What's up, brother? What's happening?
Hey.
There's been rumors these guys actually lip-sync some of the shows. I want to know if it's true.
Boys,
that would be awesome. You know, we were just talking about that in the green room, too.
You know,
about
the thing
Nicki
is
Minaj
about some of our
like
shows, like the show we're doing tomorrow night, is a special show. It's called the Old Shit Tour.
Yeah.
And it's all music we did for the 90s. You know, there's like two
But you don't lip-sync, do you?
Well, the thing is, we don't lip-sync anything, but some of our old music that we did in the early mid-90s
has the lyrics on it,
but we don't have the ability.
You know what? Hey, Howard, for one time, let them sing. I want to hear them sing. I mean,
I don't sing.
They're great.
They don't sing. They rap.
Well, let's hear them rap, for Christ's sake.
You going to pay me?
You go see them.
You going to pay me? What's up?
What am I going to see them for? I love them on the show.
Well, go see the boys. They're looking for business. Go ahead, Jamie.
Come on, man. You got to contribute to that $10 million a year that we make.
That's right. They're making $10 million.
Right. You contribute to my pocket.
Jamie, go ahead.
You guys are fucking horrible.
Yes.
Our fans are awesome, ain't they?
Don't hold back. Say what you really feel.
Well, I love the boys. What's wrong with them?
They dress like clowns.
All right, aside from that.
That is true.
I mean, is this really how... Really?
I think the clown thing is more scary than, you know, than...
When's Yucko going to join the tour? I mean, are you guys still fighting with Eminem or no?
No.
No, that's old.
That was, what, 11 years ago? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, what
you realize
this?
You couldn't fuck with them is what it was, so you back the fuck off.
All right, Jerry, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, I'm in Worcester, Massachusetts, and these guys are playing next door to a group of 80-year-old a cappella singers.
Huh?
I don't know what he means.
And listen to this. So all the fucking Juggalos are hanging out holding doors for little Jewish women. They got blood running down their face. The fucking women going to see the a cappella group are fucking crying. They're so scared.
All right, we're well, there the you go. Weird ladies, that's right.
Nice guys,
being
right?
Polite, right?
They should be in the hospital.
That's right.
It should be in the hospital. They're bleeding, right?
All right, Jack.
That sounds cool.
You've got the last word with the boys, yes.
What's up? I'm a big fan of Miami.
Thank you.
Listen, man, this guy annoys the fuck out of me. That, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? He sounds like an illiterate white nigger, man.
Wow, man. What's up with these people, man?
I hate that shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we know what you're saying. Don't repeat yourself so much, you dumbass.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Listen. Boys, I don't know how to explain this reaction. You come in here,
it's awesome, man.
This is what it's like when you go in front of a new audience.
Maybe you ought to cancel out of that gig.
This is nothing new.
No, that's why we're doing it.
You know what my theory is with these calls? These are probably Tila Tequila fans.
There you go,
that's what I think is going on. Listen, boys, I can't explain those calls. You've done it all. You've been in show business longer than most bands.